Right. But the Hebrew Israelites coming to you week in and week out to prophesy the downfall of this wicked and sinful kingdom called America, which is spiritually Rome, Egypt, Babylon, Sodom and Gomorrah. Before we go any further, we'd like to give all praises, honor, and glory to the Heavenly Father's only begotten Son, apostles, and elders, the great millstone, but teach us this truth according to the Bible, man. We're going to start like we always do, the real 12 tribes of Israel, okay? Judah, the so-called Negroes, the so-called Blacks, okay? Benjamin, the so-called Jamaicans, the West Indians, okay? Levi, the so-called Haitians, Simeon, the so-called Dominicans, Zebulun, the so-called Panamanians, Ephraim, the so-called Puerto Ricans, Manasseh, the so-called Cubans, Gad, the so-called North American Indian tribes, Reuben, the so-called Seminole Indians, Naphtali, the so-called indigenous Indians of Argentina and Chile, all right, Asher, the so-called indigenous Indians of Colombia to Uruguay, and last but not least, Issachar, the so-called Mexicans. So if you see yourself on the side according to the seed of your father, you are the biblical Israelites, and turn back to the Heavenly Father while you still have time, man.
Yeah, God, like your brother said, we are the Hebrew Israelites, you know. Come out here to preach the downfall and total annihilation of this wicked, simple kingdom and preach repentance to the elect of the nation of Israel. Because you got a lot of false prophets out here. We are to lead the lambs of Yahweh Shemel Shai back to them, you know. And we are living in the last days, the end of the days of this wicked, simple kingdom.
This is Jeremiah chapter 28, verse 8. The prophets that have been before me.
God, and what's a prophet? A prophet is a messenger from Yahweh Shemel Shai, who people ignorantly call God Jesus Christ. It says the prophets that have been before us is what the Lord has always spoken through his men. He spoke through Noah, Moses, Ezekiel, and many other great men that are written in the scriptures.
Once again, Jeremiah chapter 28, verse 8. The prophets that have been before me and before thee of old prophesied both against many countries.
Yeah, it's what they prophesied, meaning to tell you something that's going to happen before it happens. That's always been the duty of a prophet. The scriptures say the testimony of Yahweh Shai is the spirit of prophecy, so the true man of the Lord.
I get that.
Got it. Revelation 19:10.
You got it, bro? It's Revelation chapter 19, verse 10. And it reads, and I fell at his feet to worship him. Mm-hmm. And he said unto me, see thou do it not.
Yeah, because we are only supposed to worship Yahweh Shemel Shai. And what we are showing our acts, our acts of worship by coming out here in the highways and byways and doing his will.
Okay. It says, I am thy fellow servant, mm-hmm, and of thy brethren that have the testimony of Yahweh Shai.
Go ahead.
Worship the Most High, for the testimony of Yahweh Shai is the spirit of prophecy.
Yes, if you claim to have the testimony of Yahweh Shai, well, you are going to be speaking the words of prophecy. You're going to be come out here week in, week out. So look at Ezekiel 3:17, warning the people of the coming destruction that's going to soon come to this great kingdom, this wicked, simple kingdom called America, Babylon the Great, in the scriptures.
And the earth, period. You know what I'm saying? Yep. But mainly here to America. I mean, this is where the greatest definite structure is going to happen at, man. The most bodies are going to be here in America, man. Because America's bigger than what people think. You know what I'm saying? It ain't just Raleigh. Some people ain't never left Raleigh, so they think this is it now, man. America's a big landmass. What is it, like 3,000, 5,000 miles? Why? Yeah. Some tell it effect. So a lot of people here in America, man, the majority of them going to die, man. Say goodbye.
About 4,000 from here to California.
Yeah, 4,000 some change. Cause I don't know what ain't 4,000. Some change. It's some change within here. You know what I'm saying? But within all that, saying that, the majority of people here in America gonna die, man. And 24 corners of the earth, the land of Israel is gonna get hit with nukes, and there's certain other parts of the earth gonna get hit, man. But America's gonna be totally annihilated. And before it happened, tell our people about it. We prophesy of it, right?
That's why you got brothers out there in Ghana, London. They're prophesying against the kingdom that they're in as well. The Lord is not going to let anyone guiltless. If you're wicked, you're going to be judged for it.
Right. See that, bro?
That's a good, man. That's a good, bro. Yeah.
I'm gonna go right there. You call me something else too, right? This is Isaiah chapter 42, verse 9. Behold, the former things are come to pass.
Yeah, what were some of the former things? The prophecies that are written inside the Bible. Some things have already came to pass. You got World War One, you got World War Two. Those things were prophesied in the Holy Scriptures, and they surely came to pass. Why? Because the words of the Lord do not go out void.
And new things do I declare.
Yeah, and new things. We got World War Three. We got the RFID chip, which is the mark of the beast. We got a great famine, which is going to have a lot of you people be put to death out here, you know, starving to death. You have race riots. These are some of the new things that the prophets come out week in and week out to warn the people about.
Right. Before,
mainly to warn you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans back to repent to the Yahweh Hashem El Shai, you people ignorantly call God and Jesus Christ.
Somebody get Acts 3. Yeah. It says, before they spring forth, I tell you of them.
Yeah, before these things spring forth, Yahweh Hashem El Shai, someone get 2 Chronicles 36 and 15, and get Ezekiel 3 and 17 first, Michael Michelle. What? It says, before they spring forth, the Lord has sent his men to warn the people. Because what? The Lord is showing our people compassion and love, but, you know, because they despise this correction, you know, they despise this great love that the Lord is showing towards them, what they are going to receive the Lord's wrath.
Okay. This is Luke 1 and 7. As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began.
Yeah, so what? Since the beginning of time, the Lord have always spoken through his men. It's that simple. And what? You know, we know that the Lord does not change. You know, according to Malachi 3 and 6. For I am the Lord, and I change not. What? So what? The Lord is going to be doing the same thing in these times. We're just ordinary men who's been blessed with the spirit and power of Yahweh Hashem El Shai to come out here and preach these words.
Great. Precept. Hosea, which finished like Kabbalah.
That was it, yeah.
Hosea, read it again, Kabbalah.
This is Luke 1 and 70. As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been...
They waiting on the Lord to come down here and tell them something, though, right, bro? Our people still waiting on who they really call God and Jesus Christ to come down here and tell them that he sent forth his men out here to give them the word, man. The Lord said, I ain't coming, I ain't telling you now. When I come, I'm coming with fire, man. We read that every time, every week, pretty much, that scripture come out how the Lord is coming. He's coming with fire and with his angels to zap this place, man, to hail him back, man.
That's right.
And the Lord is telling you how he's going to do it, man. He's going to tell you through his servant, the prophet, then he's going to come through and make good on his word, man.
That's right. Well, even when Lord Yahweh Shai came down to the earth, he came as a man, right? You know? So what? That shows that the Lord, has a certain order of way how he wants to do things.
And the Heavenly Father, you know what I'm saying, just to add on, the Heavenly Father even spoke through his Son. Because the Lord said, what? I ain't come to do my own will. I came to do the will of the Heavenly Father. Right. So the Heavenly Father was speaking through his Son just like they speaking through us, man. Right. Giving you the same message, man. Ain't that the message didn't change, man. Are you receiving the message? Are you getting the message? That's the only thing, you know? Yes. So going right back, Hosea chapter 12, verse 10. You was finished with that, bro? That was it?
I'm gonna finish it out.
Yeah, finish it out, bro.
This is Luke 1 and 70. That we should be, 1 and 7. As he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began.
Right.
Yeah, exactly. Since the beginning of time, Yahweh Hashem El Shai has always spoken through his men. Always, always. The Lord, everything the Lord does is perfect, so he has no reason to change things up.
Yeah. Plus, the Lord said, I'm gonna always do things decently in order, man. So the order is for Heavenly Father and the Son to speak through men and give them the word so they can give you the word, man. Give you the warning, all that, man.
I mean, our people read those great accounts about, you know, Moses and how the Lord, you know, dealt with Moses personally, you know, and then what he in turn spoke to the people.
Right.
What they think the order changed, you know. Our people think time is different now because we're in 2019, you know.
Plus, our people act like they want the Heavenly Father to really speak to them. But it's a count when the Heavenly Father was going to speak to our people. He told us to go tell the people to clean themselves up for 3 days, and I'm going to come talk to them. But then as soon as they heard the thunder, the shake, rattling, and rolling, what our people say, nah, Moses, we want to talk to you, Moses. Because the Heavenly Father talked to us, all of us going to die, man. All of us going to die, because we ain't even worthy, man, for the Heavenly Father to even talk to us, man. We're not worthy, man. We filthy rags down here, man. Plus the Heavenly Father, he shall not look upon iniquity. You know what I'm saying? He ain't gonna look upon wickedness, man. He's looking through the eyes of his only begotten Son, man. That's the only way the Heavenly Father sees us, through his only begotten Son, man.
So once again, Hosea chapter 12, verse 10. I have also spoken by the prophets.
Yeah, this is Yahweh by Shema Shai speaking, you know? Who are the prophets today? Jeremiah 3:15, Abba Shah. The Lord has set up certain men on the earth to break down the scriptures to you and to give you that proper warning, you know? Right. Who aren't going to be looking for vainglory, who aren't going to be breaking down the scriptures wrong. And, it, you know, it's through the spirits, our apostles, the elders, the great Moses, and the men on down.
Right.
Who else is doing it? Who else is breaking down, you know, defending the gospel?
Somebody get Isaiah 32. Isaiah 30 and start at 20. Get what the brother called first, though. And I got a little bit more of this. Let me finish this off first.
Finish it out. And then get Jeremiah
and
Ezekiel.
He says, and I have multiplied visions and used similitudes by the ministry of the prophets.
Yes, so what, even certain men, you know, even some women have gotten you the, you know, visions, you know, that link up straight with the scriptures. And what, you have certain brothers, you know, they might be their wives, and they break down the dreams, you know, and some of them are very biblical. You know, the future current events that are going to come to this place.
Right.
It's not like the Lord projected, you know, a big TV screen in the sky to show you, to warn you. No, he could do that. But hey, you gotta believe with faith, you know, because this thing is about, having faith in that the words of the Heavenly Father are faithful and true.
Right. That's right.
This is Jeremiah 3:15.
This is Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 15. And it reads, and I will give you pastors according to my heart.
Yeah, what's a pastor? A pastor is a spiritual guide. You know, right. The Lord is giving you spiritual guide. You so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans in the Israelite borders. You see, you go back to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You know, a spiritual guide, you know, according to his heart, according to his mind. You know, to break down the scriptures and to show you what the will of Yahweh Shema Shai truly is.
This is Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 15. I will give you pastors according to my heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding.
Yeah, what? How are they feeding us now? By posting up nonstop videos? Who else is posting? You know, who else is doing it? You know? Who else is posting videos on the daily? 2-3 videos on the daily. Even more of some, then some. Right. You know? Only the men of great millstone. You know, you might have, and if you're not teaching 100% truth, it don't matter how many videos you upload.
Right.
You know, it's about teaching this thing in the sincerity, you know, at the measure that the Lord has given you.
That's right. This is Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 4. And I will set up shepherds over them, which shall feed them.
Yeah, and what are they feeding them? Once again, with the word. You know what? Because what? When we come into this thing, we are newborn babies, you know, and a newborn baby, we don't see him just grabbing a bottle and feeding himself. You know, he has to be fed. He has to be washed over.
Nurtured.
Come on, bro.
Yeah. It says, and they shall fear no more, nor be dismayed, neither shall they be lacking, save Yahweh. But see, these false prophets, you know what I'm saying, aren't doing that, so our people are lacking. The people up in these churches, they're lacking knowledge, wisdom, and understanding of the scriptures. They don't know what the hell is going on, man. You know what I'm saying? They don't know the day from the night, man. They don't know the light from the dark, man. They don't know nothing according to the Bible, man. But the true prophets of the God of the Bible are going to give our people the light, which is this word. We're going to give them the knowledge, wisdom, understanding of the scriptures, which shall be that stability when all hell breaks loose. And it's going to keep them stable now, man. So where they're not going to bug out if they don't have their light built, man. If they don't have nothing to eat, they're not going to go out and try to rob a bank, so forth and so on. No. They're going to start praying, man.
Yep, right.
That's what we do, man. When we're lacking anything, what we do, we pray for it, right?
Right.
And if you lack anything, pray for it, right? That's what the scriptures say. That's exactly what we're going to do, man. And we're going to teach our people to do the same thing, but not these pastors. Rod, hold that sign with the false prophet sign, bro. Because the God of the Bible says he's going to give you pastors according to his mind. And they're going to feed you with the knowledge, wisdom, understanding of the scriptures. It's Joe Orstein, which he's not an Israelite, but it's T.D. Jakes, Al Sharpton, Jesse Jackson, Rick Chokala, I think I said his name already. I'm saying all these other false prophets, man, are they feeding our people with the knowledge, wisdom, understanding of the scriptures? No, they're feeding them with lies, which y'all people love it so, no?
Nathaniel.
That's okay, yeah.
Nathaniel Ray, right?
Right, yeah.
Bro, watch out for the signs, bro. Go ahead. Speak on, bro.
You got that. precept.
Yeah, I got precept real fast. Okay.
This is Jeremiah chapter 7, verse 4. It says, trust ye not in lying words.
Yeah, scripture say, trust ye not in lying words, you know? Our people love to hear it. So our people love to hear lies. They love to hear that, you know, death and destruction is not coming to this place. That's why the true prophets of Yahweh, Bashem, Awashad, the men, and the men that the Lord truly sent were always hated, you know? So our people would rather hear smooth things than to trust in that. But us brothers, we're supposed to, you know, take in the bitterness of the scripture, you know, and digest it.
The truth shall set you free, not lies.
That's right.
John 8:32, the truth shall set you free, not lies, man. So everybody that's going to the church, you're not free spiritually or mentally, man. You still up under the bondage of lies, man. We'll get you killed every time, though, man. You know?
That's right.
A lie ain't never helped nobody out, man. A lie ain't never helped nobody out, man. It might have felt good. Like your woman, you know she really don't look good, but then how I look, baby, and you lie to her. You looking wonderful, baby. They ain't helping her out, man. They ain't making her want to go get some exercise on. They ain't making her want to change her diet. So the more and more these false prophets on the, and the pastors or whatever title they call themselves, the more and more they lie to our people, the worse and worse our people get, man. Because a lie ain't never helped nobody out, man.
Right.
Go ahead, bro.
This is Jeremiah chapter 7, verse 4. And it reads, trust ye not in lying words, saying.
And then slack your bro. And somebody going to put some nonsense on the thing. Paint the camera right there, bro. Love God, love people. You know what I'm saying? Love the Israelites, love the elect, put that right in front of the camera, right? Just had to be here, right? Love God. But what is love according to the Bible? Keeping the commandments of the Bible to the best of your ability. Yeah, rehearsing the right side. It's like right in front of here, though. You know what I'm saying? To make sure no matter how far we go down, you know what I'm saying? It's gonna be right there, right? Love, 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 right? But ain't what the Bible's about, man. The Bible ain't all about love, man. It's got lamentations and mournings and woes up in there, man. Last time I read. But let's bring it out, brother.
Jeremiah.
That wasn't there last week, was it?
No.
It's there this week, though. This word is getting to somebody, man. Because they know it ain't all about love. So they like your whole, hopefully if they see this message, you know what I'm saying, to make them, you know, they're trying to put that vibe out here, you know what I'm saying, on the streets. But it ain't working, man.
I got something real quick. This is 1 John 5 and 3. For this is the love of the Most High.
Right, yeah.
That we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous.
Yeah, so this is the love. This is love. This is the definition of love according to the Bible. You know, love is not some feeling. It's an action.
It says love all people, too.
Yeah, love people.
It says love all people.
Oh, yeah, love all people.
Yeah, love all people. But the scriptures don't say love all people, man. Jacob I love, Esau have I hated.
God, exactly. So what, you showing your love to Yahweh Shema Shai by doing what he commands you to do, you know? By keeping the law, such commandments to the best of your abilities, and you doing these things, you know, it doesn't grieve you.
Right.
You know, it shouldn't grieve you to have to do a lesson. It shouldn't grieve you to have to, you know, grow your beard out. You know, to restrain yourselves from eating pork, you know, and getting tattoos and things of that nature, you know, all the wickedness that our Lord hates, you know, it shouldn't grieve our people.
And then first and foremost, it shouldn't grieve you to call on the high holy names in a proper tongue in the Hebrew on your how about Shimei Awashai, man. You got our people calling the higher Shia and all this other nonsense, big man in the sky, JC, God, and whatever ever name up in the sky. I mean, nah, it grieves our people. It grieves two-thirds to call on Yahweh and his only begotten son, Lord Yahweh, man. It grieves them, man. That's part of the keeping of the law, man. Call on the name of the Heavenly Father and Son. You know that's a commandment, yo. The scriptures command us to call on our power's name, man. So go ahead, bro.
I make a quick statement. Because in Acts, the fifth chapter tells us we ought to obey the Most High brethren, men. Men tells us to love everybody. Man.
Right.
But the scripture tells us otherwise, man.
Right.
You know?
The scripture tells us on the God of the Bible, love them that love him.
That's right.
And we just live with love, being put into the Bible.
That's right.
I'll finish your statement, goodbye.
Let's
go back to the other one, though, that trust in lying words or something that you read to that effect. Well, I'm saying, read what you had first, and then I'm saying, go back to that precept.
Show you the true love to your brother, to your neighbor.
Right.
This is Leviticus chapter 19, verse 17.
I got a script on how you show love to your neighbor too, but go ahead.
Okay. This is Leviticus chapter 19, verse 17. It says, thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart. Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
Yeah, because what the scripture say, let a wise man rebuke me. It should be as a precious ornament, you know?
Right.
but we are coming out here in the highways and byways showing love. Hey, we could, you know, we'll get destroyed, but we could just let Jake die out here. We're showing the greatest love on the planet Earth. We're showing that compassion to our people. That's what we, hey, we telling them. Hey, you got to get right with the Heavenly Father. You know, you got to repent. You know, to Yahweh Shema Shah, you got to put down the pork chops. You got to put down, you know, the blunt, the cigarettes. You got to put all these things down. Come back and serve Yahweh Shema Shah.
It says, thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor and not suffer sin upon him.
Yeah, that's why we come out here week in and week out to give our people warning, you know? Hey, we telling them if they continue in their wickedness, they are going to die. Right. You know, hey, we trying to get our people back, but our people are stiff-necked. They're hard-headed. You know, they'd rather hear smooth things and lying words than hear the rough and ruggedness of this truth, you know? The bitter words.
Yeah. St. Matthew chapter 28. Verse 18, and Yahushua came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations.
Yeah, and why does it say teach all nations? Because what? The nation of Israel. Someone get real quick, James 1.
I got that script off.
Yeah,
right there.
Because what? This is the commandment, and this is what the apostles, you know, the disciples who later became apostles did, you know? And we're coming in that same spirit, doing the same thing, teaching all nations.
Because remember, you made a statement, you was like, now we could just stay at home, you know what I'm saying, not give our people the word, yeah. But then we would be destroyed. Mm-hmm. So that's why I brought this out, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's something that's exactly what to do. Like you was going into, that's love.
Yes.
Right. Us coming out here teaching this word, that's love, man.
Right.
Go ahead, brother. Say your precept.
It's James 1 and 1. James, a servant of the Most High and of the Lord Yahushua HaMashiach, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greeting.
Yeah, exactly. And that's the point. You know, greeting to the 12 tribes of the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans that are scattered abroad.
Right.
This message of love is to you. The scriptures
right.
talk about this is a labor of love.
Right.
Great.
Good news.
The good news.
The gospel. Right. St. Matthew chapter 28, I read 19 again. Go ye therefore and teach all nations. Baptizing, going right back to Isaiah the 11th chapter 2, verse 11 on down. I'm saying how we were scattered in those different countries. It says, I'm baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son, you know, and of the Holy Spirit, man. So that's a commandment right there, right?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You know,
that's right.
That's a commandment right there.
I believe it's in Corinthians, you know, the scriptures talk about how the Lord sent us not to baptize, you know, with water, but to preach the gospel,
right.
You know, and we're preaching the gospel, you know, promoting those names of Yahweh by Shema Mashiach, you know, by Shema Karkwadash.
Right. That's right. It says, teaching them to observe all things whichsoever I have commanded you.
Yeah, so what, we come out here and teach, you know, we don't come out here to get a fan base. We don't come out here to talk about social dramas, little
right.
schisms throughout Israel. No, we come out here to build up, to edify our people.
And that's that lets you know right there that it's a commandment that we teach the name of the Heavenly Father and His Son, man.
Yeah.
And we got to teach about the Holy Spirit, man, the Rakakwadash, man. That's
right.
A commandment. Teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even until the end of the world. Amen.
Yeah, so Yahweh Shai, His Spirit, is with us now, you know? Scriptures say, when two or three are gathered in my name, there I am in the midst thereof, you know?
Right. That's a reincarnation scripture, too.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Because He told the disciples this over 2,000 years ago. He said, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to be with you no matter where you go. He said, even to the ends of the world.
That's right.
That's over here in America, man.
Right.
So
right.
Let it be. Finish what you had, Kazakba. Because I got one to finish that Jeremiah. And I got one more on love.
This is a quick precept.
Yeah, go with that.
This is Jeremiah 23 and 3. And I will gather the remnant of my flock out of all countries.
Yeah, the remnant, the elect of the nation of Israel, the sheep, the lambs of Yahweh by Shema Shai, the men chosen from the foundation of the earth to do His will on the earth. Got it?
Says, out of all countries, whether I have driven them.
Yeah, exactly. So you're going to have elect members of the nation of Israel apart in every nation. In every, anywhere there's people at, you're going to have a member of the elect there out of all countries.
Right. Yeah, to be a witness unto all nations, man.
That's right.
To be a witness unto all nations that the gospel of the kingdom of heaven was preached unto them, man.
Yeah.
Ain't going to be no excuses in that day. Barely, look, have they not heard? Yes, barely they heard, man.
Right.
The sound went off throughout the four corners of the earth, man. Pretty much you got the Wi-Fi everywhere pretty much now, man, you know?
Yeah.
Somebody. Right. And if the Wi-Fi ain't there, somebody taking a trip there, you know what I'm saying? They going back telling their loved ones. Guess what I heard? So right. From some, the word and got out, man.
Right.
The Lord, you know what I'm saying, is perfect in all his ways, man. So he's going to make sure that word and got spread out.
We got people out there in the Middle East making videos about how the true Israelites need to come home, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
That tells you right there, this word's been preached all the earth, you know? That's why it's called the World Wide Web.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
This is how it says, whether I have driven them, and I will bring them again to their folds, and they shall be fruitful and increase.
Yeah, exactly. Let's talk about in the kingdom of heaven, you know? The Lord is going to deliver his elect up, you know, in those chariots, which you people ignorantly call UFOs. You know, and he's going to deliver his elect, you know, and the rest of the people are going to be destroyed for not taking heed to the warning.
That's right.
Any more
that's right. That's it on that.
Okay.
We have to turn to Jeremiah.
This is Zechariah 8:16. These are the things that ye shall do.
Yeah, this is another commandment of the Lord. The Lord is giving out commandments, but are you going to take heed? Are you going to do what the scriptures say to do? You know? Are you
going to
do your own thing?
Remember? This is Zechariah 8:16. These are the things that ye shall do. Speak ye every man the truth to his neighbor.
Yeah, it says speak ye every man the truth to his neighbor. What's the truth? The truth is this word, which the brother's about to get. And who is your neighbor? Your neighbor is the fellow Israelites, you know?
That's right.
Because what? Hey, that's our neighbor. Our neighbor is not the whole wide world.
This is Zechariah 8:16. These are the things that ye shall do. Speak ye every man the truth to his neighbor.
Yeah, so now is the time for us to speak the truth. You know, it's not later. The Lord has given us appointed time for us to preach this message of repentance. But when the Lord takes us off the scene, you know, when the Lord has race riots in the streets, you got these different army vehicles riding up the street, gunning these so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans down with the sword. Hey, we're not going to be out here. You know, we're not going to be given warning. Our job is to give the warning before the destruction comes.
And look, that's love.
Yep. Right.
And that's love, man. We're showing love right now, man. Okay? Your pastors in these churches, they're not showing love, man. Teaching you lies, that's not love, man. Somebody's been lying to me my whole life. They wasn't showing me love, man.
Right.
You know, the Israelites, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, they have never been shown love over here in America, man. Because first and foremost, you call them black. When they're the Hebrew Israelites. So that was the first step of you hating them, man. You know, among other things, I can go down the line, man. I can be out here for a couple hours, man, showing you hate according to American ways towards the Israelites, man. But I stopped just right there, man. Calling us black, that was hate. Not teaching us the truth, that's hate, man.
Yep.
You want that right quick?
Yeah, real quick.
This is St. John chapter 17, verse 17. Read letter, Lord Yahweh speaking. Who they ignorantly call Jesus Christ, right? Sanctify them through thy truth.
You look at that word sanctify, it means to separate, to make holy, you know?
Right.
So we are sanctifying, we are cleansing our people with the word, you know, from the filth and the pollution and the lies that this wicked, simple kingdom promotes.
Right. Thy word is truth.
Yes, what? How are we doing that? By the words of the Yahweh Shema Shai. Not by our words, you know, but by the words of the Lord. This word is what's bringing down this kingdom. These words of the Lord is what's healing our people, building them up for the time of destruction that's coming to this place.
You got people that'll come up in there, but like, how do I know if you're teaching the truth or they're teaching the truth? We just read it. When they're speaking, if they speak not according to this word, there's no life or truth in them, man.
Right.
So that's how you know who got the truth, man. And the truth is only going to be revealed to the elect, man. Because whether we got the truth or whether we speak in lies, the God of the Bible says the deceiver and the deceiver is. So the God of the Bible, he got the spirit to put on you for you to believe in a lie, man. The scriptures say that, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
They have believed in lies and not the truth.
Yeah. definition?
This is the definition of truth. It says that which is true or accordingness with fact or reality.
Yeah, and these are the facts. The reality of the of this thing is that whether you people believe it or not, the words of Yahweh Bashima Shah are gonna come to pass.
Right.
That's gonna be reality. And it is reality, you know.
Somebody gets second Ezra the 15th chapter, I think it's 3. You know what I'm saying? Yep. These words of faith and the truth, just that one verse.
This is 2nd Ezra chapter 15, verse 2. And cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and true.
Yeah, the words of Yahweh Hashem Shai, the Holy Bible, you know, 1611 version, including the Apocrypha, those words are faithful and true. They've been tested, they've been tried. You know, do you truly have faith to believe that the Lord really flooded the earth? Do you truly have faith to believe that the Lord delivered Daniel out of the lion's den? You know, do you believe in the accounts that are supposed to comfort us for these troubling times that are coming to America?
That was it?
Yeah, that was it. We got 2 precepts right quick. Okay,
St. John chapter 8, verse 32, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
Yeah, the truth is going to make you free. It's going to unlock that block that's on your mind, you know? But it's going to allow us to understand that, hey, this isn't the end-all, be-all. That soon enough, Yahweh Shema Hashai, he promised that he was going to deliver a remnant of people out of America.
Right.
That this gives us hope. This gives us a surety of his word.
And out of the place that they were scattered at. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Not just America, but all the places they were scattered at, man. Yeah. It's all about that small remnant, the elect, man. Ain't about 2/3, man. 2/3 can walk past us a million times, man. Is we gonna lose any sleep, brothers? Because the majority of our people walk past the words of the Bible that we're speaking. Are we gonna lose any sleep, brothers? We ain't gonna lose no sleep, man. Because our people don't want to take heed to the words of the Bible that we're speaking out here. But then they go to church tomorrow and get a pastor $100, you know what I'm saying, to lie to them, right? It's all good, man. It's gonna be all good soon come when death and destruction come here to America, man. So you ain't gotta take heed, man. Am I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth?
Read it in, bro.
This is Galatians 4:16. Am I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth?
God, that's a question. You know, our people, we come here week in and week out telling you that all your little comforts and stabilities that you trust in America are going to be taken away.
Might hold that on decks. What is it? So Rock 5 and 7?
Yeah. And not only that, but the Lord, hey, we're freely giving you the words of the Lord. We are giving you a gift, you know? Whether you want to receive it or not is not really, it's up to the Lord.
Yeah.
But what we are, you know, we are offering you that gift. That gift is being presented, you know? And whether you walk by it, we tell you week in and week out, hey, receive this word and you're going to be protected. You're going to be taken care of.
Receive with meekness, though.
Yeah, and receive with all humbleness, you know? But that's who the Lord is dealing with, the humble, those that admit their faults to Yahweh Shemal Shai.
Admit that they ain't known that. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Scripture say freely give, freely receive.
Right.
We didn't pay for this.
Right.
You know, we didn't go to, go buy this knowledge.
Right.
So nobody charges somebody for it, man.
Right.
You know? I remember one last time.
Yeah.
This is Galatians 4:16. And my therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth.
Yeah, have we become your so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans enemies? The answer is yes, you know. Hey, that's why, you know, we're being persecuted. That's why you come up, you know, bucking up against the truth. Hey, you're not bucking up against us, you're bucking up against the words of Yahweh Shemal and Shai. We are just the mouthpiece, the messengers of the Lord. You gain a lot of enemies for speaking the truth unto our people.
We tell our people they ain't black. I am black, man. I'm black, man. I'm blacker than black of the black, black, man. You know? You can't tell me that, man. I was born black and I'm going to die black, man. Our people, look, I am Chicano. I'm Chicano. Nah, man. You're an Israelite, man, from one of your perspective tribes. And that's the truth, man.
That's right.
That was the end of that Kabbalah, that Galatians. This is St. John chapter 8, verse 45. And because I tell you the truth, ye believe me not. So we tell our people the truth according to the Bible, and they still don't believe it, man.
Right.
But that's prophecy, though, at the same time, because the scripture tell you 2/3 of our people won't going to receive this word anyway, man.
Right.
Because they have been given eyes that they can't see, ears that they can't hear spiritually, man. So of course they hear what we say, and they actually see us, but they're not going to
take heed.
The spirit is not on him to take heed.
Right.
So that was it on that. That's it. That was on St. John 8.
Zechariah 8:16. Speak ye and truth to his neighbor. Execute the judgment of truth and peace in your gates.
Yeah, so we come here week in and week out, and we tell you the judgments of Yahweh Bashim Ha'oshah. We tell you the penalties of breaking the law, statutes, commandments, for not having faith, and ultimately for not fearing your power, you know? The penalty is going to be due by getting mauled by lions and bears, you know, and tigers, you know?
Oh, my.
Oh, my, yeah.
Right, you know what I'm saying?
That the penalty is you starving to death, you know?
I think we have
you know, that you might have to commit cannibalism on your young ones, mm-hmm. you know? These are the penalties and judgments of Yahweh Bashim Ha'oshah, and we do it in the gates, you know, in the beginning of the cities.
Oh, the scriptures say, he that despises his word shall be destroyed. But he that fears the commandment shall be rewarded.
Right.
And I got the rest of that scripture in St. John. I won't finish. Okay. St. John chapter 8, I'm going to jump down to verse 47. He that is of Yahweh heareth Yahweh's words.
Yeah, he you know, because what our people are carnal. You know, he that is of Yahweh by Shema Hashem, I mean, what those men whom the Lord has chosen to receive this word are going to receive it. It's that simple.
That's right. Men, women, and children.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's the prophets that's going to be teaching it, though. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
And you got, you know what I'm saying? You got shit. You got men of the Lord that came in at young ages. You know what I'm saying? You got brothers, sons, you know what I'm saying, and daughters believing in Yahweh Bashim Ha'oshah at a young age. But they received the word, right, with meekness, right? But the scripture tells us to come as a newborn babe anyway, man.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So once again, St. John chapter 8, verse 47. He that is of Yahweh, Bashim Ha'oshah, who the English call God and Jesus Christ, here's Yahweh's words.
Yeah, exactly. What? You read up on verse 44, it says, ye are your father the devil, you know, and the lust of your father you would do.
Right.
Two-thirds of these so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, you're after the will of this Edomite.
Right.
You're after pleasing him. You're after his desires
right.
and what he delights in.
Right.
But the elect of the nation of Israel, those who are allowed to receive this word, are going to be doing the will of Yahweh Bashim Ha'oshah. They're not going to be having sex on the Sabbath.
Right.
You know? They're not going to be teaching men lies and teaching them they don't have to keep the commandments,
right.
you know?
It's like, as long as our people can put a smile on Esau's face, they don't care if the Heavenly Father and Son is angry as hell at them and pissed off at them, as long as Esau's happy, right? That's going to be their downfall, though, right? So once again, St. John chapter 8, verse 47, he that is of Yahweh, heareth Yahweh's word. Ye therefore hear them not, because ye are not of the Most High.
Yeah, what? You turn the deaf ear to these words. You can't understand the words that are coming out of our mouths.
You know the Most High ain't dealing with heart, you know what I'm saying? don't listen to those guys. But the scripture just said that, right? The scripture just said, he that is of the Most High is going to hear what we're saying, man.
Right.
Going right back to St. Luke 10 and 16. He that heareth you, heareth me, man. Somebody can hold that on deck. What you saying, though, bro?
Yeah, she got an ankle bracelet on. She can't even walk.
Right. Or talk.
Yeah,
I'll talk, that mouth done, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
The mouth done, you know what I'm saying? No teeth, you know what I'm saying? No teeth. Queen no teeth, you know what I'm saying? Queen no teeth, y'all. And then after you finish that, Zechariah. You finish that?
Yeah,
I got a precept for that, Zechariah.
Because okay.
look, we this commandment right there, it wants to show love, right? So we're showing love. Look, yeah. Tough love.
Okay.
Tough love, right? That's the best kind of love anyway, tough love.
Right.
See, America don't teach tough love. America teach fighting, man. You can't even whip your kids here, man. You
right.
can't show your kids tough love here in America. Why are you so harsh? Why are you so rude? Because the scriptures tell us to be rude, man. You know? Now, you don't straight up be a tyrant of your household, but it's a time and a place for everything, man. I know you got to put your house in order, right? And America's going to push that, right? This is Exodus chapter 21. Matter of fact, Exodus chapter 18, verse 21. Moreover, Exodus chapter 18, verse 21. Moreover, thou shalt provide out of all the people able men, such as fear the Most High, men of truth.
Men of truth, you know, and that's our where Apostle St. Elder's a great millstone, and the men on down. You know, men that are going to be speaking the words of Yahweh Bashim Ha'oshah, ultimately the leaders of the nation of Israel.
Right.
You know, because
right.
the elect. You know, the first fruits, they're the leaders of the, starting with the men, of course, they're the leaders of the nation of Israel, you know?
The real Israelites. Not the fake ones, the real ones. You're looking at the real Hebrew Israelites, you know? Not the fake ones, you know? All right? And when he came up out of that stupor, man, when he came from that dust, man, he brought us out of the dust, man, out of the state of confusion, man. And then we stand upon our feet now, man. It's a wonderful thing.
Yeah.
Moreover, Exodus chapter 18, verse 21. Moreover, thou shalt provide out of all the people, the Israelites, yeah, exactly. Of course,
yeah.
Able men, such as fear the Most High.
Yeah, able men. Men that can come out here on the highways and byways, you know, stand for a couple hours, you know, put up with the elements.
Right.
You aren't going to be complaining and whining,
right.
You know, and most definitely not women, you know, because women were not given that spirit to come teach the word.
Right. Such as fear the Most High.
Yeah, and that's the point. Such that fear Yahweh by Shema and Shai. Because what, if you fear Yahweh Shema and Shai, you're going to do exactly what he commands you to do.
Right.
The people on that sign, show that sign rock. The people on that sign, they don't fear the God of the Bible. We're talking about the Israelites, man. Of course, these heathens don't. But the Israelites that's on that sign, the TD snakes, the Al Sharptons, the Kurt Frankensteins, the Nate Satans,
right.
The Bubble Eye Blackfish Faces, so forth and so on. Look, man, the Shaka Homos, the Saw Niggas, they don't fear the God of the Bible, man. The Martin Lucifer Kings,
right.
Things of that nature. Kanye West, man, he ain't on that sign. But Louis Farrakhan, he up there. Oh, yeah, he is up there. He is up there. Brother. He is up there. The fucking, what's that dude? Eddie Longthorns. Y'all fear the God of the Bible. Because ain't no fear in them, man.
Right. Because
they ain't speaking the truth, man.
Yep.
That's how you know who fear the God of the Bible. Because they're going to speak the truth according to the Bible.
Yeah. They're going to be reading out the scriptures.
Right. It says, hating covetousness.
Hating covetousness, you know? That's desiring something that's not yours,
right.
Something that another person has.
That's right.
You know, they're not going to be desiring, you know, coveting after what another brother's gifts, you
right.
know? Another brother might be really good in the Hebrew,
right.
You know? You might desire spiritual gifts, but you're not going to hate that brother for having
right.
them, you know?
You don't want to take his place.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You want something to happen to him so you can come up on the level, man, and be acknowledged. Nah, yo.
Yeah.
The men of the Lord ain't gonna do that, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
He says, and place such oaths.
Yeah, because scriptures say when one is glorified, well, we are all glorified together.
Yeah.
You know, we're a body.
Right.
You know, we can all do this as, you know, a body, or we can lose as individuals pretty
yep.
much, you know?
Right, brother. He says, and place such over them. To be rulers of thousands.
Yep, so you got certain men that are rulers of thousands, you know, who are over the nation of Israel, you know, judging up, giving out orders, decrees. You know, that's why Elder Apostle Har said, what, do 3 bills a week, you know, and then some.
Man, somebody gonna always be over you, man.
Yep.
Right, you know? It says rulers, look, it says to be rulers of thousands. A ruler have people up out of them, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, you can't go to the ruler and act like you're going to rule over him. Nah, he's over you. But then that ruler got somebody ruling over him. But say it's just the order of things.
I mean, say, where you think he so got it from?
Right.
You know, the military, any of these law enforcement offices, you have your rookies, you have your lieutenants, you have your chiefs, you have your captains, all the way up, man.
Right. It says, rulers of thousands and rulers of hundreds. Rulers of 50s and rulers of 10s. And that's the point, man. The God of the Bible, you know what I'm saying, going to have men that fear him. They're going to speak the truth, man. And that's love right there.
Right.
When you want to talk about love, love the Most High, love all people. Well, that's love right there, man.
Right.
Okay? I want to finish that Jeremiah 28. Yeah, I ain't finished that.
Yeah, because what? Y'all by Shema Shai.
You're
showing our people
up. But they look at it as hate, though, right? They call it hate because the so-called white man call what we're doing, they call it hate speech. When we're actually showing true love, man. Because the so-called white men don't want us to come out here and warn our people, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
To turn back from that wickedness. It doesn't promote his kingdom, man. What we're doing doesn't promote his kingdom to keep going on, man.
Right.
Yeah, it doesn't benefit his kingdom, man. What we're doing doesn't benefit the so-called white man's kingdom, telling our people to turn back from their wickedness. It doesn't
right.
promote that, man. Go ahead.
This is 2 Chronicles 36 and 15. Mm-hmm. And the Lord power of their fathers
yep.
sent to them by messengers.
Yeah, go ahead.
rising up betimes.
Yeah, so Yahweh Shemaoshai sent to our forefathers, you know, and is doing the same thing today, his prophets, his messengers, to deliver his message. And it said betimes, you know, early, rising up early before the definite destruction comes, giving that that love, that warning, you know?
Right. Right.
So look, we can stand upon the high tower and just watch the destruction come. That's showing hate.
Right.
You know, that's what these false pastors, these false leaders, such as Daniel 7, telling our people that tribulation isn't coming to this place.
Right.
You know, you got no light, teaching, you know, Egyptology. They're not warning our people of the death and destruction that's coming. They're
right.
Showing the most hate. But what, they have the unity camps acting like they're promoting love. The true love is coming out of the highways and byways and telling our people to, hey, either get right, because what, you have, your life is at stake.
Yep.
Your family's life, lives are at stake. Your loved ones,
yep.
their lives are at stake, you know?
Yep,
right. It reads on. 2 Chronicles 36 and 15, and the Lord power of their fathers sent to them by his messengers, mm-hmm. rising up betimes and sent ascending.
Yeah, so what, we didn't come out here on our own accord. The Lord put the spirit on certain men to go out there and preach his word.
And it says rising up early, you know what I'm saying, before that death and destruction came, man. You know? Because at noonday, you know what it is. You know what I'm saying? That's when that death and destruction is going to come, man.
Right.
So the God of the Bible got us rising early, man, before that judgment really come down upon this place, man. And
right.
Give our people a warning, man. You can't show no more love than that, man. For the God of the Bible, because the Lord didn't have to do it, man. He could have just brung fire, man, and destroyed all of us. But he sent forth the apostles and the elders of great millstone to give us the truth according to the Bible. Now, the God of the Bible got us standing upon our feet now, man. Giving our people the same warning, yo. The message didn't change, man.
Right.
It's the same message, man. From the top down to the bottom, man. Same message, man.
Just like, hey, when the Lord, when our people, went, just like you brought earlier, how our people wanted to talk to the Lord, he was like, well, they got 3 days to get right.
Right.
You know, sanctify themselves. They better get right.
Get her done.
You know, they want to come see me.
Right.
Okay.
This is Ezekiel 38 and 17. Thus saith the Lord, power, art thou he of whom I have spoken in old time by my servants, the prophets of Israel.
Yeah, exactly. So what? The Lord is doing the same thing over and over again. He sent his prophets out early. We're standing upon the high tower watching for the incoming enemies. We're telling you that the so-called white man, you know, wants to bring
what's
the
this? Like, bro, what's them hawks?
Yeah, those look like, what they call them?
They look like hawks, you know what I'm saying?
Like
but, look, but look how many of them it is, though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's like seven of them.
Yeah.
It's a complete number of them, yo, hovering around the city, man.
Right.
Ready to pounce upon that prey, man. The Lord showing signs, man, what he going to do to these people, man.
Yeah.
Go ahead, brother.
Yeah. It's Ezekiel 38 and 17. Thus saith the Lord, power, art thou he of whom I have spoken in old time by my servants, the prophets of Israel.
Yep. So the prophets are going to be Israelites,
right.
And they're going to be giving a warning to their people. We don't care about the heathens, you know. Most importantly, Yahweh Shemaoshai doesn't care about the heathens.
Right.
It says, which prophesied in those days, many years, that I will bring thee against them.
Yeah, well, it prophesied, I mean, what they told you, they told you the things that were going to happen before they happened, you know. So we have said that upon the high tower, giving warning to our people. We are telling our people that the so-called white man, that the Lord is about to use the so-called white man to bring death and destruction to our people, you know?
Right.
He's gonna be gunning our people down, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, with his M16, his assault rifles, you know, his military vehicles, and many other weapons that haven't even been put out there yet, you know?
Right.
That was it. And then it's like, the scripture said they prophesied for years, man, just like Noah.
Yeah.
Noah prophesied for years. Oh yeah, it ain't gonna come to pass. It ain't happened yet. 120 years, it ain't happened yet, Noah. You ain't telling the truth, Noah. Same thing with the apostles, you know what I'm saying? 30 years and better. Y'all ain't telling the truth. Y'all false prophets. Y'all said it was gonna come in the year 2000. Well, sure, we can't actually give you a date, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
We can pray for that date, though. Right. Still say we're gonna desire to see the day of the Lord, and ain't gonna see it, man.
Right.
So we've been out here for some years now telling the people in this city alone, man, the death and destruction is gonna come. Oh yeah, y'all been out here for years. Where is it at? Where is it at? So it's gonna come, though.
Right.
Do it, Terry.
Wait
on it, man.
I'm gonna finish out this
last
one.
Yeah, man.
Burn on
me. I know, right?
This is second.
I wanna finish that Jeremiah, too.
God.
It's the 2 Chronicles 36:15. It says, and the Lord power of their fathers sent to them by these messengers, rising up betimes and sending, because he had compassion on his people.
Yeah, so that's why the Lord sends us out here, you know? Because he's having compassion on his people. And someone look at that word compassion, the Lord is showing forth that love to you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans.
But in mercy.
Yeah, exactly.
God, the Bible is actually showing our people mercy with us being out here, man. But our people take it for granted, though. The Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, they take this precious moment right here, they take it for granted.
Right.
The God of the Bible, you have, but you know, it's actually showing up people mercy. But then they like mercy, the hell with mercy. It's left mercy to the ground. You're like, the hell with mercy, yo. I don't need mercy, yo. The so-called white man's gonna help me when all hell break loose. My food stamp's gonna help me when all hell break loose. But the God of the Bible saying, none of that gonna help you when all hell break loose, you know?
Yeah, and a lot of our people, you know, man, those guys been out there for a while, it might not happen, so they like faith. They don't want to be put on Broad Street. They're scared to come out. You know, what if my girlfriend see me out there? You
right.
know, what if one of my family members see me? You know, they're right. ashamed to come out here and preach the words of Yahweh Bashi Mount Shai. These people are ignorant called God and Jesus Christ.
But they don't mind going to like Woodstock or something like that with a whole lot of drugs and a whole lot of crime and all that. They don't mind being seen standing on the block with the drug dealer, though. You know what I'm saying? They don't mind being seen hanging out inside the trap house, right? But you got a problem with being out here hearing men preaching the words of the Bible? Two-thirds of y'all need to be destroyed, man.
Right.
That's why the scripture says, woe unto them that call evil good and good evil, you know? That put that darkness for light. Our people don't want to stand up for righteousness' sake.
Got the definition of compassion. It says, sympathetic pity.
Yeah, the Lord's showing sympathy. He's showing pity. Mercy unto you so-called niggers, Latinos, and Native Americans.
A.K.A. love.
Yep, love.
It says, concern for the sufferings or misfortune of others.
Hey, we have been very misfortunate. We are the bottom of the barrel here in America. The Lord saying, hey, you know, come back and repent, you know, seek my face, you know, get into these scriptures, get into this word, hey, and get this wisdom, knowledge, understanding of the scriptures. And he's going to have that mercy and compassion upon our people. But our people despise that, you know? Scriptures say,
despise means to hate.
They that despise these words are going to basically be destroyed.
Yeah. Basically. Yeah. I'm saying nothing hard about it. I'm saying it's black and white. It's real basic, man. Take heed to the word, you know what I'm saying, and live. Don't take heed to the word and die, man. Real basic, man. Plain. Plain, even, right? Yeah. Say he made a plain upon tables, right?
Yeah.
What else you got, Kazakba?
Yeah, so just a little more. It says sympathy, feeling. It says love.
Love, there it is.
Remember that song, Feelings, Nothing But Feelings. You know what I'm saying? That's the Lord, man, showing compassion, man, showing emotion to our people, man. But they like, nah, yo, I'm good, yo. I'm good without the Lord, man. Us thinking that we was good without the Lord's help, man, ended us here, man.
Right.
We ended up here in America, man, begging for bread, yo, begging for a job, man, begging for a handout, man. And the God of the Bible was like, yo, you don't need no more handouts. You don't need to beg no more. Come back to me, yo. You ain't got to go to these other nations for nothing. But our people are like, nah, yo. I want to go to these other nations for something. You know what I'm saying? I want to continue on being a slave to this Edomite devil, man. I don't want to bow down to Yahweh by Shinyal Shai. I want to be a slave to Esau, man.
Yep.
You're going to die with your slave master then, man.
Right.
Go ahead.
So last two, it says, mercy and kindness.
Hey, mercy and kindness, you know? So you call this what we're doing a message of hate? According to the Holy Scriptures, according to the Bible, which you people claim, you know, that you have on your desktop every weekend, and this is a message of hate, and this is a message of love according to the Lord, you know?
Plus, your enemy ain't gonna come out and give you no words like that, man. Right. I'm saying your enemy is gonna always show you hate. Your enemy is always gonna be cruel to you, man. Because the tender mercies of the wicked are cruel, man. So even when this devil's acting like he's showing you love, shit, man, what? Him giving you some GMO food, that's love. Know what I'm saying, bro? Him giving you a cable box, you know what I'm saying, but a camera and that motherfucker watching everything, that's love, right? And the thing, man, go on, you know what I mean?
Here it is, you know, you got that water crisis.
I'm gonna say that too.
You know, I forgot where it was. You know, it's New York.
Michigan. And down here too.
Yeah.
Everywhere.
You know, they giving out expired war bottles.
Yeah.
You know, that's showing you that, hey, this devil, this Edomite don't really care about you. But what the Lord is showing that he cares about you.
But that's why people love them. Yep. They keep voting for him. They keep doing everything this man say, man. You know? And they don't do nothing to God or the Bible say. So that lets you know who your people love, man.
Yeah.
You know?
I'm going to add on to that. Compassion, do better. It says pity. It says to be gentle.
You know? Hey, the Lord is being gentle with our people now.
He said, I was wroth with my people. Remember, the Lord was wroth with us, you know what I'm saying? The Lord, you know what I'm saying, consumed us, you know what I'm saying, with the slavery and all that, man. But not totally, though. But he could if he wanted to, though.
Yeah, the Lord always shows his compassion. Mm-hmm. Jeremiah 30 and 16, you know, can someone get it real quick? Get Jeremiah 30 and 15 and read verse 16. Because it's going to show that the Lord, hey, even though he brought this this destruction of our people, hey, at the end of the day, he's going to show the nation of Israel mercy. But right now, starting with the elect.
This is Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 15. Mm-hmm. Why criest thou for thy affliction?
Go ahead.
Thy sorrow is incurable for the multitude of thy iniquity.
Yeah, blood, because what? Now that Jake is catching all type of hell, now they want to cry unto the Lord. Now that we were in slavery, you know, catching all types of hell, we should have been crying unto the Lord before then. Go ahead.
It says, because thy sins were increased.
But the thing about in slavery, you know what I'm saying? We was calling, but not on the right name.
Yeah.
So the Lord's like, I'm not hearing you. If you're not calling on the right name, it's like, once again, a guy walking down the street, his name is Mike, but you like, hey, Leroy. Hey, Leroy. Is Mike going to turn around? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Mike ain't going to turn around because you calling him Leroy. Right. It's just like your high voice, your mouth is not going to hear you if you calling on God and Jesus Christ, man. Because that's not their name, man. So, of course, we were sighing and crying in slavery. Help me, Lord. Lord is just a title, man. God is just a title. You had to call them the proper names in the Hebrew tongue, which all that was taken away from us. So the Lord is showing us mercy again by giving us those names to call on, man. Right. That's why the Lord is showing us mercy now. When we call on the name, we turn back, man. We repent, man.
Right.
And you go back to the ancient times, anytime Israel started repenting, they started sighing and crying, calling on those heavenly, high holy names, Lord sent the Savior, man.
That's right.
It says, because thou sins were increased, mm-hmm. I have done these things unto thee.
Yeah, the Lord brought us down low because what? Our sins were increased. Well, let's hear the flip side. Go ahead.
Verse 16. Therefore, all they that devour thee shall be devoured.
Yeah, but what? I'm going to rise up against your enemies, you know, in the appointed time.
Yep.
Hey, I'm judging you now, but don't worry. I'm going to judge these heathens as well. That's the Lord showing us that mercy. You know, he chastened us, but for a moment, you know, only for our betterment, you know, for our correction. And that's why we come out here week in and week out to rebuke our people. You know, it might seem harsh for that moment, but what? If you repent and turn back sorrowfully, it's going to be up for your betterment.
Right.
It says,
plus the example that we always use, if somebody get ready across the street and a Mack truck is coming,
yeah,
brother, a Mack truck is coming. Brother, no, we're not gonna say that. It's gonna be harsh, it's gonna be loud, it's gonna be rude.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be straightforward, man. That's and look, and being that way is gonna save that person's life, right? But if you like, hey, you saying it to the person, and he hearing you say a Mack truck is coming, you know what I'm saying? Nah, we let them know that a Mack truck is coming, man.
Right.
And yeah, it might be rough, it might be harsh and all that, but and then you get saved from that damn truck that was about to smash you to pieces, man. That's all that counts, right? That you still alive, right?
Yeah.
You took heed to the warning, now you still alive. That's all that matter, man.
Right.
It ain't about how the warning came out, man. Our people are effeminate over here, though, man.
Yep.
It says
go
verse
ahead.
16.
If I may, you want to say something? Go ahead, read it.
It says verse 16. Therefore, all they that devour thee shall be devoured,
mm-hmm.
and all thine adversaries, every one of them.
Yeah, like the bro was going to that example with the harsh warning. You know, that's why the scripture says, for the terror of the Lord, we persuade men.
Facts.
You know, we say, hey, watch out. You say, what? What are you saying?
Bam.
We scare them.
Right.
That's why the scripture says, serve the Lord, fear and trembling. So move the F out the way.
That's right.
He's going to hold and like, he's going to jump and get scared.
Yep.
So when you hear these words in the truth, in entirety, you know, we break down the scriptures correct and speak the truth to our people, it's going to scare them.
Right.
The truth is scary, you know? knowing that, hey, America's about to be destroyed, you know? And you don't know if you're going to make it out of here. That's why, well, we're seeking our power. We're seeking to cleave off the Yahweh Shema which I do.
Right. Yeah, I think it's something to bring up. Just to make that statement. Yeah. That's what the brother was saying. You know? It's like someone's blind. They get ready to cross the street. They can't see the Mack truck coming.
Right.
That's our people. Our people are spiritually blind. We're telling them, look, man, devil destruction is about to hit you in the face, man. Right. Repent and turn back to the Heavenly Father before you get smashed by that Mack truck, man.
Right. I got something.
All right,
got it. Did you, brother, was holding something?
Yeah.
But you are, I'm saying, was you reading something and holding something?
I was holding something.
But yeah. You hadn't started reading.
No.
Ezekiel chapter 33, verse 1. Again, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, speak to the children of thy people.
Yeah, so the scripture says, Yahweh Shema Hashah has commanded us to come here in the highways and byways and to speak to you so-called people like you in the Native American. If you truly got faith that the things that are gonna, the things that are written in the scriptures are gonna happen, you're gonna come out here and speak about it.
Right. I believe, therefore I have spoken.
That's right.
It says, and say unto them, when I bring the sword upon a land.
And that's what we come out here and tell our people. The Lord's about to bring a sword to this land. You know, these different killing instruments. He's going to put the spirit on these wild animals. Every major city got a zoo, don't it?
Yep.
Those animals are going to break out. A lot of them are electric locked. When the power goes out, the gates are going to open. The animals are going to get out. And it's going to be a hunt season for these animals. And you people are the prey.
Right. And then not even a species ain't even got to have zoos. They got woods, right?
Yeah.
That's where the animals hide at, woods. They're the worst kind right there, man. Yeah, the animals just in them, yeah. The ones in the wild, they're the worst kind, man. I seen when the lights went out for a couple of hours, I seen foxes coming through my neighborhood, man. You know what I'm saying? What?
It's a lion in Durham.
Right, see what I'm saying? There's a lion running around the streets of Durham, yo. These people are through, man. If a lion is running through the streets of Durham, these people are through, man. And panthers and all that, man, running around, man. He says, and say unto them, when I bring the sword upon the land, and them lions need to go through Durham anyway, man. A whole lot of lions and hyenas need to go through the streets of Durham, man. Eat all them knuckleheads alive, man. Every last one of them, man. He says, when I bring the sword upon the land, somebody's brother trying to get somebody.
Yeah.
It says, if the people of the land take a man of their coast instead of watch and set him for their watchman.
Yeah, who are the watchmen? Yahweh Shema Hashah says the apostle holds a great millstone to be the watchman, you know, to warn the people.
Say, bro?
Yeah, I'm sorry, bud. You know, Yahweh Shema Hashah, he said the apostle holds a great millstone to be the watchman. Well, a majority of our people, they set up Joel Osteen. You know, they set up these false pastors and they trust in God.
Right.
And their watchmen are not going to blow the trumpet.
Right. Okay? It says, if the people of the land take a man of their coast and set him for their watchman,
yeah.
If when he seeth the sword come upon the land, he blow the trumpet.
And we see the sword coming, you know? The Lord has given us the vision, the prophets, you know, the men that were allotted to be teachers, you know, and
visionaries
to warn the people. You know, we see the sword coming, so what? We blowing the trumpet. The trumpet that we're blowing is the sound of our voice, you know? Yep. The alarm of war.
Yeah, because we actually see death and destruction coming, man.
That's right.
We actually see death and destruction coming, man. Right. We see it, man, with a clear eyes view, man.
That's right.
You see them nukes being tested. Me and the brother Rock did on that the other night. Fire's coming. We see the fire coming, so we got to warn our people, man.
Right.
Can't play around like it's all lovey-dovey, man. And these dire straight times, man. You better not be playing around, man.
You watching, you see the fire coming. You're in the tower like this.
Right.
Man,
eating and drinking water, right?
Eating, just sitting there relaxing. You know, you got the alarm button right there next to you.
Right.
You know, but you ain't pushing the button to warn the people.
Right. So them people are dying, they're saying that blood on your hands. Somebody gonna kill you. Somebody's gonna be left alive and they're gonna avenge their family members' blood on you, man.
Right.
You see those ancient movies, it always happened like that, man. One dude was set up to warn the people, to help the people out alive, and say, you know, he ended up getting alive and he think everybody died. But if somebody, you know what I'm saying, is up on a pile of rubbish, you know what I'm saying? You see him walking up in the sunset, they're like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? And they say, you know, like 20 years later, you know what I'm saying, he meet up with the dude. You don't remember him, but he remember you. He chopped your head off, man. That's what's going to happen if you don't warn the people, man.
Right. But some of these watchmen, they might see the warning, and they might just haul ass without even warning.
Yeah.
Without
right off the tower, right, bro?
Yeah, right off the tower and abandon their post. Right. You know?
Got a secret rope on the side, right? And slide down and haul ass. But then there's one person still alive seeing you haul ass like this motherfucker. Then he got to go warn everybody. He's like, yo, my life desire is to find him. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He spent his whole life searching for that dude and then warn the people, man.
Yeah.
It says, I read that last part. If he see if the sword come. Now, let me read up some.
Okay.
It says, he blow the trumpet and warn the people.
Yeah, and that's what we do week in and week out. We come out on the highways and byways with brothers, make videos, post them on the internet, post them on the YouTube, non-stop. Hey, warn the people, you know, that World War III is coming.
Right.
That a famine is going to hit the land of America, that different diseases are pestilent. Mm-hmm. And not only that, that they're already here.
Yeah.
And on a small scale.
That's right.
A very small scale. The Lord is going to amp things up even more when the warning is over.
He gonna look the plagues of Egypt, you know what I'm saying, hitting America already, man. Like right about now, you can't even go into the water, man.
Yeah.
Right about now, you can't even go in the water, just like in ancient Egypt, you couldn't go in the water. Moses! Yeah, you know what I'm saying? He plagued the water, man.
Yeah. You see these people are panicking before the destruction comes. How much more when the destruction actually comes?
Right.
You got that movie Clash of the Titans. You know, they were like, the Kraken is coming. You know, everybody's panicking in the city.
Yeah.
But what happens, you know, if you would actually destroy the city, everybody would be even more scared.
Right.
You know? They would have died.
That's right. It says, if when he seeth the sword come upon the land, he blow the trumpet and warn the people.
Yeah, go ahead.
So we see everything coming down the pipeline, so we got to warn our people. Hold post about that. We got to warn our people. Knowing that all these things coming down the pipeline, we most definitely got to warn our people.
Yeah.
Martial law is going to pop off, man. And them gargoyle trees going to come in your house, man, and kick your door down, kill you, rape you, and take everything in your crib. We got to warn our people that those things are coming. Can't be playing around, man. Act like we don't know what time it is. It says, it's a time to speak, and it's a time to keep silence.
Yep.
This is the time to speak, because soon come the God of the Bible going to make his men silent, man.
We're telling you that the most precious thing that you can be storing up right now is the understanding of this truth.
Right.
You know? This is the most valuable thing out on the planet Earth. Hey, this truth is not going to depreciate.
Right.
The value, you know, of trusting the Lord is never going to depreciate.
Right.
So now it's now or never.
Right.
You got to stir it up in your mind.
That's right. It says, he heard the sound, then whosoever heareth the sound of the trumpet and take him not warning, if the sword come and take him away, his blood shall be upon his own head.
Yeah, so our people walking up and down the streets, you know, acting all laxy-daisy, you know, week in and week out.
These women going to be ravished too in that day, man.
Yep.
These women going to be ravished in that day, man. You watch now. You know?
Where? Like the brother always say, being pretty is going to be a curse in that.
Right.
You know, it's a blessing. You know, you get different perks in society for, you know, having a cute face, nice body in society. That's soon enough for those who don't repent of the Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, or the family of Israel. You know what? It's going to be for your demise.
Look, and these pretty boys, too, you know what I'm saying? Because these prison guys, they love pretty boys. They don't come out and wreck them, too. Pretty girls, pretty gals, you know what I'm saying? And pretty boys, you know what I'm saying? Going to get ravished in that day, man. You walk around trying to be a pretty boy, and that day when all hell break loose, these guys are breaking out of prison, man. It's going to get up in you, man. They're going to get her done, man. They're going to get her done. You know what I'm saying?
If I may say real fast, they show you that in that movie Friday. David got it.
Yeah.
Fresh
Meat.
The pimp.
Oh, yeah. And Mike Epps.
Cat Williams.
Yeah, Cat Williams.
Cat Williams.
Oh, yeah.
You know? Fresh Meat online.
Yeah.
Got Fresh Meat. Fresh Meat. That's what these guys, these pretty boys out here, you know what I'm saying? They're always lining up their beard, wearing lipstick, arching their eyebrows. Them prison guys, when they get out, you know what I'm saying? They'll come looking for you, man.
Right.
The men of the Lord always look rough, man.
Right.
Listen, the men of the Lord ain't too many people really looking at the men of the Lord. Like, nah, he look like he's going through something. Nah.
Yeah, yeah.
Look, I want him over there. You know what I'm saying? Him over there with the line up with the cornrows and all that. Looking all pretty with the edges and all that. That's what they going to get, man, that day, man.
Yeah. Right. Hey, and these prisons are right here next to these major cities.
Yeah.
You know, I'm talking to some people. They go, I can't believe that the jail is right there. It's literally in my backyard, you know? And
backyard, yeah.
Literally,
so,
you know?
So that means the prisoners been watching them there. know what I'm saying? So the prisoners been watching them there like, yo, that's, they done put claims on them already then, bro. Like, yo, that's me right there. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, right, right. That's me over there. They're like, yeah, we know, boss. We know, boss. We have a little brother, boss. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's a guy in the prison that's running everything. Yep. Then he got underlings, you know what I'm saying? It's like, yo, anything else, you know what I'm saying? He said, everything else is for y'all, you know what I'm saying? Right. But you heard Damien saying it Friday, yep. That's mine right there. Y'all can have the rest of the party, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. My brother Kazab by just, it's a prison right down the block.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A major prison.
Yeah.
Right next
There's another one down that way too. Yeah. A major prison.
Right next NC State.
Guys doing push-ups right now as we speak, you know what I'm saying? Going to get it. You know what I'm saying? And then they're gonna look out there one like, yeah, he's still there over there. Yeah. It's gonna go down soon, come.
Man, Lord said, we're going to get that new
suit
come.
Right.
We're going to be able to get these people.
Right,
right. Can I freak them go down?
Right.
Man, let's get it.
It says, he heard the sound of the trumpet and took not warning.
Yep. And that's the majority of people. They're not taking warning. And they'd be up here listening. They have their Bibles out, pen and paper, a notepad, a highlighter.
Yep.
You know, taking notes.
Some.
Right now, Isaiah 33:6.
Yep.
Proverbs 4:7. You know, trust in the Lord.
That's right, the things that were written the fourth time were written for our learning. Yep. It says he heard the sound of the trumpet.
Look, have they not heard? Yes, barely they heard.
The Lord telling them right, and you heard.
Right.
You heard the warning.
That's right. And look, and took not warning.
Took not warning.
Right. It says, his blood shall be upon him. But he that taketh warning shall be delivered.
Yeah, but he that taketh warning, he that believeth that the words of Yahweh Shema Shai, you people alien called God and Jesus Christ, are faithful and true, and you believe by faith, hey, you have a chance to be delivered.
Right.
You know?
Well, actually says, he that taketh warning shall deliver his soul. Doing all right. You know who you are according to the Bible? You know who you are according to the Bible?
Who am I?
See yourself on the side? One side you got our slave names, and then on the other side, you got our biblical names. Right. We are here to let our people know who they are according to the Bible.
God,
where's
your church located?
Right here. You know, this is where we assemble, this is where we gather to teach our people. You know, because if we had a church in the building,
At the same time, the God of the Bible left a record of his son. So like the brother said, for truth's sake, you know what I'm saying, the color of the Lord is important. You know what I'm saying? That's just like, so like your father, you know what I'm saying, he got a house, and that's how you know he move off. Somebody bring him to the house and put their image up on the wall. That's how you know they say, that's your daddy right there. You're gonna look at that picture and say, oh yeah, that color, that picture right there, it don't matter. Nah, you're gonna go against that picture right there, man. You know?
Our people
going in the air, man.
We telling our people, the Lord is coming back.
Right.
And you gotta be out on the lookout for him.
Right.
You got these project blue beams. You know, and they're gonna be promoting the image of Cesare Borgia. And our people are gonna fall for that and believe that that's really the Lord. So we come out here and tell the truth according to the Bible.
I wanna bring this out right quick. This is 1 John 5:10. Everybody say they love the words of the Lord. Well, but listen up then. 1 John 5:10. He that believeth on the Son of the Most High, who they ignorantly call Jesus Christ, right, have the witness in himself. He that believeth not, the color of the Lord don't matter, right? That's a person that don't believe, right? He that believeth not, the Most High have made him a liar, because he believeth not the record that the God of the Bible gave of his Son. So it's a record of how the God of the Bible gave his Son. It's a record of the Son of the Lord, man, and how he looked, man. And how he's coming back looking, man. You know, a green man ain't coming back. A man with dark skin is coming back to save his people. We must believe on it as the scripture have said, man.
I say John 7:38. He that believeth on me, as the scripture have said.
Yes, you gotta believe on the Heavenly Father and through His only begotten Son, how the Scripture says.
Right.
Hey, the Scripture says He's a dark skinned man, you know, well, woolly hair.
And the Bible don't say the color of the Lord don't matter. That's what man said. Man made that up, man. That's a lot of man made up. What does Scripture say again, bro?
This is St. John 7.
Hold on, the Scripture's coming out. You got to respect the Scriptures now. Go ahead.
He that believeth on me, as the Scripture has said.
Right, and we're coming straight out the Bible, the same way it's in your church. Go ahead.
It says, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water.
Yeah, out of his mind, the man who believes in Yahweh by Shema Shah, you people ignorantly call God in his grace, is going to understand the Scripture. They're going to understand the Word because they believe. They have that faith that, but there's an account in the Scripture of how our Lord looked. Hey, I believe in that.
Right.
There's an account of how our Lord spoke.
The Scripture say, blessed are those that haven't seen. Hold on, the Scripture say, what the Scripture say? Let the women learn and sign and don't use authority over the men. I'm saying, that's what the Scripture say. The Scripture say, if you let us make our point right quick, we're going to let you ask your questions. Let us bring our point out first, though. I'm saying, this is the Lord's platform, you know? It's the Lord's platform. You can't go in your church and ask your pastor name. You do everything decently in order in there. Let's do it the same way out here, please. Please. Read what you got, bro, again.
This is St. John 7:38. It's written in red, so it's the Lord speaking. He that believeth on me, as the Scripture hath said.
And the Scripture give an account of what the Lord looked like. So we got to believe on the Lord, as the Scripture have said, not what man say. Man always someone, the color of the Lord don't matter. But the Lord said, he that believeth on me, as the Scripture have said. We got to believe what the Scripture say. Not what we think. We can't keep leaning into our own understanding, man. Just blah, 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 blah. Pull out the Scriptures and show us what you talk about. It's true. Read, bro.
St. John 7:38. He that believeth on me, as the Scripture have said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water.
Out of that man's mind, he's gonna have the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the Scriptures, you know?
Right.
It's that simple. You gotta believe on the words of the Lord in its entirety. You can't only half believe. Oh yeah, I don't really care what he looks like. Hey, but the Lord, our people, the Israelites, we like taking pictures of ourselves.
Right.
The Lord wouldn't have put the account in the Bible, you know, claim to believe in if it didn't matter. It does matter.
Let me say this one thing. I do know one thing.
Born in
that part of the world, Jesus
will not fight after
that. Well,
really, don't even really matter what part of the world, because you got Eskimos in Alaska that's darker than this brother right here, so it don't really matter what region of the earth you were born in. But we understand what you're saying, though. But you know, our people don't really want to hear the word, though. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. That's the definition of record. Bring it, brother. This is the definition of record. It says, a set down in writing, it says, or other permanent form for later reference.
It says something you write down in writing for a later reference, because the Lord knows, the God of the Bible knew from the beginning of time that the wicked were going to set this image.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
now people are going to fall for it. So she's coming to that Florida Air Spirit anyway, to where it's like, you know what I'm saying, JJ, you know what I'm saying, Michael revealed to Florida, you know what I'm saying, Evan, because you know, she looked like Florida Evan a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Did you get her, bro? Did you get her, brother?
Yeah, I got
you know what I'm saying? You got Florida Evans, right? Florida Evans comes up to the camp, and she still believes in white Jesus, man. Yep. Just like, you know what I'm saying, good times, man. That's Florida Evans coming back in the spirit, man. You know, Michael said, Mom, you know what I'm saying? In the Bible, it says the Lord, you know what I'm saying, had dark skins. No, it didn't, Michael. No, it didn't, Michael. But Michael showed it. Y'all brothers throwing it down too, man. You know what I'm saying? Florida Evans got showed in the Scriptures what the color of the Lord looked like. And the first thing she says, well, no, it ain't. So she ain't never read the Scriptures for herself. She just went on with that pastor told her. So it's the God that I grew up with, you know what I'm saying? And it's the God that I always loved, man. Well, the people that taught you about the God of the Bible really didn't teach you the truth according to the Bible, man. So she coming in that Florida Evan spirit. Look, this is what I grew up on, and this is what I'm stuck with, you know what I'm saying? Our people don't want to change into the truth. They love lies once again, man.
Yep.
The Lord left a record of what his son looked like, man. And he that believeth on him, as the Scriptures say, out of his belly, meaning his mind, gonna flow rivers of living water. You're gonna increase learning, man. You're gonna always be stagnant. That's old water right there. That's an old bottle right there, man. Can't get nothing in that old bottle, man. Everything's straight up leaked on out, man. Just want to over talk the Scripture. You old heads, man, sit it down, man. You old heads, sit it down, man. Unless you're coming in the spirit of Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh, Shai, man. You gotta come up here as a newborn babe, yo. I always talking about where y'all church at, right here. You know she going to church tomorrow. He the main one up in there, got that short haircut too. That's that prideful spirit, man. That's really our woman mourning, man. You know, when Jay used to shave off their hair back in the ancient times, the sign of mourning, man. So she really crying out right about now, even though she don't know it, but we know it. But read what you got, bro.
This second Ezra's 15:2 again. And cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and true.
Which we read there earlier. Here we go again.
Hey, because the Lord left the record here in the scriptures. Hey, and the account that the Lord left about him being a dark-skinned man, you know, having woolly hair, having a beard on his face, you know, his different characteristics, those are faithful and true. We are to believe in that.
Somebody know what that scripture where it says, having not seen, ye believe. You know what I'm saying? Somebody type that up. It's in the New Command. Yeah. It's in the New Testament, dog. Having not seen, ye believe. Something to that effect. Because we ain't seen our Lord and Savior, Lord Yahweh Shai, in over 2,000 years. But we still believe the record, man. You know? That's why our brothers increase. Every day to go by, knowledge is increasing, man. Why? Because we believe on the Lord, as the scripture have said, man. We don't never come out of our mouth talking about you got it, bro? Read it, bro.
I think it's John 20:29.
You sure that's the one?
First Peter. Yep. That's the one. That's it. I think.
What about that? First Peter 1:8. Yeah, get First Peter 1:8 first. Get First Peter 1:8 first. We didn't bring yours out because I thought somebody get it right quick. Whoever get it. Whether it's on your phone or in the store, whoever get it, bring it out.
First Peter 1:8.
Yeah.
This is First Peter.
Because we're always looking. That's why it's always about the basics, man. You got to go back to the basics, man. Our Jake don't know that, man. So coming out here trying to be all deep by people, you know what I'm saying? And y'all people ain't on that level yet, man. Our people, matter of fact, ain't on no level, man. Right. So you got to come out here and feed them baby food, man. Straight up milk, man. And that milk is deep within itself, man. You got God's tired of bringing out milk. You know, are you crazy, yo? That's that foundation, man. Our people need milk. Can't eat meat yet, man. Go ahead, bro.
This is First Peter chapter 1, verse 8.
Right.
Whom having not seen, ye love with, in whom though now ye see him not, yet believing.
Exactly. No sense. We believe on the Heavenly Father and the Son, as the scripture have said, man.
Right.
How they coming, what they look like, what they gonna do, who they love, all that, man. We believe it according to the scriptures, man. You know? The color of the Lord don't matter, man. Come on, man. Who says that, man? Right. Only a fool would say that, man. And the Lord have made them a liar, man. But they believe not the record, man. Right. That the Heavenly Father gave of his only begotten Son, man. Which that definition went heavy, man. That you brought out, man. An ancient record, you know what I'm saying? For later time, something to that effect, man. A reference left for the future, man. What the thing? Get Romans right quick, bro. Romans 15:4. Bring that out right quick. And then I want you to read that one more time, because I bought that 1 Peter 1:8, but somebody read that Romans right quick. Romans 15:5.
This is Romans chapter 15, verse 4.
Yeah.
It says, for whatsoever things were written aforetime,
right,
were written for our learning.
So everything that we're reading was written for our learning, man. The God of the Bible left a record of his Son, man. You know? And who we love and everything else, man, this Bible is a book of records, man. You know what I'm saying? A book of laws, statutes, commandments, man. A way for us to live, man. And it was all written for our learning, what to eat, what not to eat, what to do, and what not to do, man. So we're supposed to say, nah, we ain't gonna go by what this say no more. You know what I'm saying? We won't go by what the church about and say, you don't even open up this no more. Nah, we're not gonna do that, man. We're gonna believe in thus saith the Lord, thus saith the Bible, man. And it is what it is. The Lord didn't put the spirit on them to believe anyway, man. You know what I'm saying? Jake don't believe. That old woman wanted to come and use a sort of authority over us, man.
Right.
That's all she wanted because we young, right? So I got something to say. Well, hey, you kept talking, though. You know what I'm saying? If I say, can I say something? That means I'm going to say something real quick and then I'm going to stop, right? She wanted to just keep going. She really didn't want to have nothing to say. She wanted to try to tell us something, man.
Yep.
You know, having something to say and telling us something is two different things, man.
Right.
Go ahead, bro.
This is a definition of record. It says, set down in writing. Mm. Or something
was written on stone, wasn't it, bro? Know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
It says, or something other permanent, form for later reference, especially officially.
Mm. So this is official. Know what I'm saying? What they say, official tissue. Yeah. Know what I'm saying? Something to that effect. Uh-huh. This is official, man. Straight up, man. Non-GMO, man. You either believe it or don't believe it, man. And we see once again, the majority of our people don't believe in this scripture. You had a dude come by, I was in South Carolina last week. You had a dude come up to the camp. He came up to the camp looking all bugged out. He had a Chucky doll with him. You know what I'm saying? A fake knife. He came and he asked one of the brethren, you know what I'm saying? And what are they doing? They reading out the Bible? He's like, yeah, they're reading out the Bible. He's like, oh, I don't believe in that. And he shot down the street. Non-believer. It's going to be destroyed soon. Come. That woman was a non-believer, man. I don't want to hear your old ass talk about nothing, y'all. Right. Nothing, man. You're an old bottle, y'all.
I got a quick hit. It's Mark 2 and 22. And no man put a new wine to old bottles.
Yep.
Helps the new wine do a burst. The bottles burst the bottles and the wine is spilled.
Because what? Our people, they got everything they thought they knew, they got to throw it out. You know? When you come into this knowledge, you got to be born again. A newborn baby doesn't know anything. He has to be taught. He has, like brother said, he has to be nurtured. He has to be built up again.
Right.
You know, we are tearing down the lies that our people have been taught and bringing them back up, building them up for truth.
It's Mark 2 and 22. It says, and the wine is spilled, and the bottles will be marked, but new wine must be put into new bottles.
Mm. Yeah, and that was an old bottle. That was a full bottle of that.
Right.
She had, you can't, hey, you got a water bottle, you got, to put something else and you gotta dump everything else.
Right.
You gotta clear that mind with this word. You gotta wash on that filth, that pollution that you learned in the world.
Yeah. I got something, bro. Make your statement first.
You know, and just to use a reference for that, you know, when you have a bottle of anything, that liquid deteriorates the bottle.
Yeah.
And everything. You know, that woman had the liquid or the wine of this world in her,
yeah,
that deteriorated her mind, man,
yeah,
to which she has the truth. Pour it in there, it's not gonna retain it, man.
Yeah.
It's gonna start leaking like the skin.
She can't receive what meekness being graphic words.
All right.
You know what I'm saying? She can humble herself down. Cause what? You got some young men out here on the highways and byways that look like her, and she like, nah, yo. You gotta be an old head, you gotta look like T.D. Chase, you know what I'm saying? Committed this to you. You gotta look like Peep Show Dollar. You know what I'm saying? They're pushing that madness, man. Everybody on that sign, they're pushing that madness. The Lord, the call of the Lord don't matter, man. Not the true man of the Lord. This is James chapter 1, verse 21. Wherefore, lay apart all filthiness and superfluity.
Yes, yes. So what we tell our people, to lay apart all that wickedness that you been taught and those lies that you've been brought up to believe in the world, hey, and come back and receive this word, you know? That this world is polluted, you know? And the scriptures talk about how the words of the Heavenly Father are pure, you know? No chasings.
Right.
This world, it's all watered down. It's all clunky and disgusting. The water's dirty, you know, and that's why our people love to drink.
Wisdom would not enter into a malicious soul, yo.
Yep.
She wicked as hell, man. Yep. So the God of the Bible, you have but she mouth is not gonna kill. She the same one, man. She had that Jezebel spirit on her, yo. It was more than one Jezebel too, man. You know what I'm saying? She was just one, cause you think it won't?
Right.
You think one? It ain't nothing new up under the sun. It was just one main Jezebel that was written over the scriptures. But look, man, come on. When we see Jezebels every day,
right,
we saw one a couple of weeks ago, right?
Yep.
Then we see one before her. It's different ones, man. So ain't nothing new up under the sun. It was always women that was down with the world. You know what I'm saying? They wanted the men of the Lord destroyed.
Yep.
Who was telling the men a violation to be the head of the household? The woman like, hell no. He need to get out of here. You know what I'm saying? We need to get him out of here. And they came up with a coup, man, to kill all the men of the Lord, man. They said Jezebel, you know what I'm saying, had all the men of the Lord killed, man. I think prophets had to hide out in caves and everything, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, hide from these witches, man.
Yeah.
And she's one of them, man.
Because what, you know, every cult leader has, you know, every, you know, these different wicked leaders of our nation,
yeah,
they all got followers,
yep,
right? And they embody that spirit that is on that wicked follower.
And then they all got wives, too, you know what I'm saying? Talking in their ear, man, that pillow talk, man. You need to do this, you need to do that, you know what I'm saying? I don't like him, you know what I'm saying? I think he's trying to overthrow you, this, that, and the third. Putting lies in their ears, man. And if you weak body, you know what I'm saying, you're going to fall for that nonsense. But reading on, one more time, James chapter 1, verse 21. Wherefore, lay apart all filthiness and superfluity of naughtiness.
Yeah, all that excess of wickedness, you know? Our people commit wickedness upon wickedness. Here it is, be corrected according to the scriptures, you know, that you're not supposed to assert a third authority over the man. No, but she didn't want to humble herself,
right,
you know? So when she disobeyed the words of Heavenly Father, and she showed how proud she was.
Yep.
She wanted to show the world what she knew,
yep,
at least us anyways.
Yeah.
You know, what she knew, when she didn't know anything,
right,
you know? Scriptures talk about when a man talking, he showed that he's a fool,
right,
you know? And that's what she did. She showed herself as that she was a fool,
right,
and she didn't know anything.
That's right. It says,
and receive with meekness the engrafted word.
Because if she was meek, if she was humble, hey, she was like, oh, my bad, brothers, you know, let me sit back and listen.
Yeah. Or whenever y'all get a chance, I'm thinking, I just ask one question.
Yeah, exactly.
She would have came very humble, man, and we would have seen it and would have dealt with her. You know what I'm saying? We would have dealt with her accordingly.
And the Lord would have drawn nigh unto her.
Yeah.
You know, the Spirit of the Lord would have drawn nigh unto her, but the proud, the Lord resisted, you know?
She's probably single, because these women will tell you, yo, I'm not submissive. I heard this woman on the bus yesterday telling this other woman that she's not wifey material. She was like, yo, I'm not the woman. I'm not submissive at all. I'm not going to do whatever a man tell me to do. I ain't going to just be doing what he tell me to do. Well, you're going to die soon, come near. Because all these women are going to submit soon, come, man. All of them are going to submit. You're going to submit to somebody.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Whether willingly or unwillingly. But right. You will submit, though. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You're going to submit, though, man. He says, and receive with meekness the engrafted word, which is able to save your soul.
Yeah, so you what? Hey, there it was. Yahweh Shema Shai, people ignorantly call God in Jesus Christ, gave her an opportunity.
Yep.
Right there, she could have saved her soul. She could have had a chance to get on the chariot and got delivered from this definite instruction that's coming to a place.
Yeah.
Hey, it says, hey, deliver the soul. It goes back to the warning, you know? Mm-hmm. We gave her the warning, you know? We were trying to tell her that she was an Israelite. She was like, you know what? She didn't even regard that she was an Israelite. She was, you know what? I know the Bible said it, but, you know, it doesn't really matter what you look like.
Yeah.
She didn't want to hear the word.
She didn't consider.
Nope.
Didn't even consider.
The ball was too full to take that part in. Mm-hmm. You know, it just spilled right on side of her ears, you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
She ain't used to that alkaline, you know what I'm saying? She's that GMO, you know what I'm saying, bro?
That's sick.
Yeah. Probably got gout and everything. Man. Getting ready to get it. Yeah. She probably got gout or getting ready to get it. One.
Yeah. I got this definition of warning. And that's what he was going to earlier.
Yeah.
This definition of warning, it says, a statement or event that indicates a possible or impending danger.
Yeah, and that's what we tell her. Hey, it's not possible. It's going to happen.
Fact.
It's a fact. You know, it's a threat. You know?
Lord Terry, wait on it.
Yep, and it's an impending danger.
Dang.
There's danger coming to America. You ain't gonna always be able to walk up and down these streets. Danger, you know, these different predators are gonna be coming out among you people.
Mm-hmm.
These people are very naive. They're very foolish, you know?
The brother said there was a report of a lion running through the streets of Durham.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? There's reports of a lion running through the streets of Durham. What are these people going to do when a lion starts running after them, man?
Right.
When a lion or a tiger or a bear or my start chasing after them. And the scripture's going to that, man. Jeremiah, what is it, the 15th chapter? It goes into how these different animals and in the Apocrypha. It goes into how all these vicious animals are going to be attacking these people, ripping their clothes off and everything. And trust me, a lion going to eat through them clothes, man.
Yep.
It's going to rip their clothes off, man. Straight up, man. I want blood.
Here it is, the lion's going through Durham. I was staying inside the house.
Right.
I had a cop tell me they're doing DUI checks or whatever. I was like, cops are going to be out tonight. I'm staying home.
Right.
It's not even a whole DUI thing. It's just, I don't want to deal with the
right. You heard it warning.
Yeah, I'm staying home tonight.
Right. And don't even get searched when you don't have to get searched.
Yeah.
You know, be among the crowd.
The cops all look for an excuse, you know, to pin something on Jake.
Right. What else, brother got?
Yeah, it's Wisdom of Solomon 4 and 8. It says, for the honorable age is not that which standeth in the length of time.
Yeah, because like, she was an older woman,
right.
You know? Don't mean that she's honorable. Hey, if she was an honorable person, she would have came up here humbly. She probably wouldn't have been out here, to be honest.
Yeah.
Let's just be honest.
I mean, she probably would have been out here just going to get something to eat. You know what I'm saying? Going on about her business. She had a plate. You know what I'm saying, her hand. She had something to eat, maybe some groceries.
Maybe
she was out here shopping and all that.
Yeah.
You know, where's your husband at, though?
Yeah.
Should be walking with somebody, though. Mm-hmm. Unless he's sent out to go get something right quick.
Yeah.
She ran him away 30 years ago.
Yeah. Ran him away about 40 years ago. Like the brother said. You know what I'm saying? All in that. These men don't keep putting on with you women, man. You aggravating ass women either, man. Straight up, you loud mouth ass women, man. Men been tired of that nonsense. Real men, anyway. Been tired of that. It's gonna be a whole lot of you single women getting thrown in that concentration camp soon, come.
Right.
Look at these dudes. Selfies, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? People are crazy, y'all. But nonetheless, go ahead.
It's Wisdom of Solomon 4 and 8. For the honorable age is not that which standeth the length of time.
Mm-hmm. Oh, y'all know that other scripture, the ones that contend with them that be younger than them. Somebody know what that said? The age people that contend with the people younger than them. We young men are in the highways and byways of these old fools. You know what I'm saying? These old bottles come up, they want to fight us, you know what I'm saying? Because we got the wisdom and they don't, man. That's all it is. I have given them thy word, and the whole world have hated them, man. So these people hate us because the God of the Bible gave us the word, man. That's plain.
Read some of Solomon 4 and 8. It says, for the honorable age is not that which standeth in length of time, nor that is measured by the number of years.
Yeah, here it is, this chieftain on the planet Earth, for God knows how long, being taught lies her whole life. And here it is, she's trying to teach lies to us, you know? Or teach lies to her people.
Trying to sell us lies, and we ain't buying it.
Yeah, we ain't buying.
Right. We're giving truth for free, but she's trying to sell us lies. We're not buying. You know? Going around selling lies, man. Selling false dreams, false hope, and all that, man. Nobody don't want. No, look, once she came out with that nonsense, we don't want to hear nothing else you got to say, yo. The only thing she kept doing is mumbling, yo. I'm ignoring her, yo.
Yeah. Because a majority of our people, when they were young, they heard this truth. They've been pushed out since the 70s.
Yeah.
I've had so called friends in the world. Go back and tell their fathers, like, oh, yeah, I heard that when I was young. You know?
See?
They heard this truth.
Yep.
She heard this before, you know? And then she always had that opinion in her mind.
Doubt it.
That doubt it. Hey, it never seeped in because she was always a full bottle.
Yeah.
Sirach 42 and 8. Be not ashamed to inform the unwise and foolish.
And that was that lady, man. She was unwise and she was foolish, man. You know what I'm saying? Fools make mockery in the word, man. Oh, yeah. Fools say knowledge, too. You know what I'm saying? So she showed that she was a blockhead. She was a meatball. Yeah, that was somebody's mama. That was somebody's grandma, somebody's sister, somebody's daughter. But she was still a fool, man.
Right?
You know what I'm saying? You know.
Yeah,
she was still a fool, man. Read from the top, bro.
This Sirach, Ecclesiastes in the Apocrypha, chapter 42, verse 8. Be not ashamed to inform
the. We ain't ashamed. I think we scared to say something to the old people walking by that don't know nothing. We had to give our people warning because the God of the Bible revealed the sickness and the mystery to us by way of the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, man.
Yep. Right. Our people, they had their chance to stand up for the Lord to fight, you know?
Right.
When they were young, when they received this word.
Right.
You know, when she probably heard this word, she was probably in the early, mid-20s.
Yeah.
You know, she was young.
Didn't try to make no garments or nothing. You know what I'm saying? Right. Didn't try to bake no cakes, nothing. Right. Didn't try to do nothing for the men of the Lord. Right. But they was out back then.
Yeah.
Didn't try to, calm it down, their attitude down. And you can tell she was fiery back then. But she just met a match today, though.
Right.
You know, because the God of the Bible said, well, I'm going to make your foreheads harder than their foreheads. Because she tried to come at us kind of hard now. That ain't going to work, though. This ain't our first rodeo. We dealt with it decently in order, though. You know what I'm saying? You know? But we let her know, yo, we ain't no pushovers, man. Go ahead, though, bro.
Plus, the Lord's no respected person.
Right. Yeah.
That same spirit, man.
Right.
That's somebody's grandma, man. That's somebody's mama, man.
Right.
And? Tell that to the Lord.
Right.
The scriptures say, you shall, in judgment, you shall not have respect the person,
right.
You know? Because if we do, that's sin unto us.
Right.
If we would just say, you know, have a great day, granny, you know, or sit here and mumble.
She would have still been here talking, though.
Yeah, exactly.
She would have still, tell me the scriptures we done brung out, if we would have let her say what she wanted to say, she would have still, no scriptures would have came out. She would have still, 30 minutes later, she would have still been talking, man. She should have said, all right, y'all, God is love. She probably the one to put them things down the ground, too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Knowing her. Or told somebody to do it.
Right.
You better do something. You know what I'm saying? They talking about there, put something out there that says love and do it.
Right.
Go ahead.
This is,
now you got it.
Okay. Sirach 42 and 8. Be not ashamed to inform the unwise and foolish.
Because the majority of our people don't know nothing, man. So we got to come out here and inform the unwise. That's the majority of our people, even you old heads, man.
Right.
But y'all don't know nothing. Y'all old. Y'all a bunch of old fools, man.
All right.
You think a person, you know what I'm saying, get up in age, they're supposed to know something, right? They know a bunch of folly, man. Like the scriptures say, the knowledge of wickedness is not wisdom. So that's the only thing they've been learning is wickedness, man.
Yeah, because normally, you know, wine, as they get older, is supposed to age.
Right.
But they've been taught that their wine has been contaminated,
right,
you know?
Right.
So while it was sitting inside the bottle, it got mold inside. Mm-hmm. It got all these different diseases.
Yeah.
But if it was that pure wine, you know, the scriptures, the word,
right?
What it would have aged, you
all
know?
Kind of bacteria up in it, you know what I'm saying,
yep.
Bro? Bacteria that came up in that thing, you know what I'm saying?
It got contaminated.
Yeah, it got contaminated. Oh yeah, the, like the Lord said, you know, he's gonna preserve his elect. You know what I'm saying? She wasn't one of the ones that was preserved. She got contaminated, you know what I'm saying?
Those fresh bottles, you know? Right. That's that pure one, you know?
She didn't have the bottles, you know what I'm saying? You know the bottles that brothers get, you know what I'm saying, for their northern oils. You know what I'm saying? The mason jars, you know what I'm saying, for their kind of copper, amber color.
Yeah.
They the best one. She got one of the clear ones that you put out, what's that liquor, that moonshine in? She got one with the clear bottle, you know what I'm saying? You put the moonshine in, with the sun, you know what I'm saying, kept penetrating through.
Yeah.
And you got them, bacteria.
Bacteria.
You know what I'm saying? Because if you ain't got that bottle, that kind of brown amber bottle, like the brothers be getting, you know what I'm saying? If you got it sitting in the sun too long, you know what I'm saying? The sun rays, I start damaging it, you know what I'm saying?
Yep.
It's the wrong kind of bottle. Right? Yeah, that was the wrong kind of bottle, you know what I'm saying?
Different oils, you know?
Right.
It ain't never happened to us, but it basically, it gets molded.
Yeah,
so it gets
yeah.
Mold, yep. And I forgot, it gets something else. I can't remember the word.
Yeah.
The properties run out.
Yeah, exactly. Yep. The nutrients in it is no longer in there. It gets burned out of it.
Right.
Because you see these different supplements?
It was just an empty bottle, you know what I'm saying? Period, you know what I'm saying? If you sit a bottle there too long, you know what I'm saying? Anything that's in it just evaporates over time. It was just a straight up empty bottle. Then bring out like two more and then I'll roll you stuff up.
This is Sirach 42 and 8. Be not ashamed to inform the unwise and foolish. Because I'm going to make a quick statement. Because that's what they promote here. You want to respect your elders.
Yeah.
And it was your elders a demon being out of order, we ain't gonna respect that,
right,
man.
That's right.
Well, we're supposed to straight up now just keep our mouth shut, right? Don't say nothing, right? Just let her have the flow, right? Let her have the flow. Let her spew up madness right now, man. I mean, we could have did it for edification purposes, man, but ain't nothing coming out of that.
You couldn't even really hear what she was saying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I heard, you know, I heard.
I
heard.
I
heard.
I was like,
I heard.
I heard.
I heard.
I heard.
I heard.
I
heard.
I heard it perfectly because I answered what she had said, right?
Yeah.
My brother Isaac was like, yo, you got some good ears, girl. You heard that? Like, yeah, I heard that, man. One of them gifts, man.
Yeah.
Gift of hearing.
It says, and foolish in the extreme age.
Yeah, and she was, that's an example, you know? We can't be ashamed to correct our people with what they have given up the fight, you know? They're going to be the majority of these old heads, you know, they're going to be destroyed on this side. They have given up the fight. They have given up when y'all by Shimon Shah. They had a chance when they were young. This truth has been out for decades now, you know?
Right.
You don't think she heard this word? This ain't the first time.
Right. But it might be the last. It ain't the first, but it might be the last, man. And the Lord might do something to that old lady walking down the street, man. He might just do something.
It says, Sirach 42 and 8, it says, in the extreme age, they contended with those that are young.
Yeah, she was contending with us, trying to fight against the words of Yahweh Shemal Shai.
Yep, right.
Coming up, spewing her madness.
Because we were young. Because we were young. Let's say she look at us as her grandsons, man, like, yo, let me go school them right quick. Whenever she came up, what's up, fellas? What's up, fellas? I said, what's up, guys? What's up, guys? She said, how y'all doing, man? Oh, we guys, right? Why not? How y'all doing, man? How y'all men doing? How about that?
Right.
What's up, guys? What's up, guys? So she looking at us as insignificant, pretty much.
This is Sirach 42 and 8. Be not ashamed to inform the unwise and foolish and the extreme age that contendeth with those that are young. Thus shalt thou be truly learned and approved of all men living.
What does that last part say again, bro?
Yep, it says, thus shalt thou be truly learned.
Right.
And approved of all men living.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? If you come up, you know what I'm saying? Let us teach you. You know what I'm saying? You gonna learn something, basically. But if you come up here trying to fight against them and contend and fight against everything that we say according to the Bible, everything we say is according to the Bible, but our people contend. You don't learn nothing that way, man. Right. You're always trying to fight against the Spirit, man. The Scripture tell you that too, man. They always resist the Holy Spirit, man. Yep. They're a kakwadash, man.
Right.
You know, they ain't gonna never receive what meekness did grab the word, man. Something's gonna have to happen to the majority of our people, man. The Lord's gonna have to do something. You know what I'm saying? To make our people submit, man. Because hearing the word ain't good enough anyway, man. For our people. For the majority of our people anyway.
Yeah.
the scriptures say your teachers should not be bold and corny, the more than told you early. We the teachers, man.
Right.
Through the spirit of power, you have by Shimmy Yahweh Shai.
Right.
She's sitting back and just, you know, keep her on her chops.
Right. I'm an old ass college professor. You know what I'm saying? She knew the thing, she knew the wisdom of this word, which is foolishness to the Most High. You could tell she graduated college or something like that, probably.
Yeah.
Went to a couple of different schools. You know what I'm saying? Probably St. Aug's, something like that, Shaw.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Probably alumni.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Which ain't nothing to the God of the Bible, man.
Right.
This is the knowledge that the God of the Bible want our people to receive.
Yeah.
Not that nonsense.
Right.
We don't want to hear about how many people right. you didn't, you know what I'm saying, taught and all that. Nonsense, man.
Yeah, scripture say, if any man be wise in this world, let him become a fool, they may become wise, yep. You know?
If any man speak, let him speak of the oracles of the Most High. Just roughly paraphrasing.
Yep.
You know?
Sirach 5:7, make no tarry and turn to the Lord.
Yeah, so make no tarry to turn to Yahweh by Shema and Shai. Why? Because definite instruction is going to come. It's going to come for the majority of our people.
No,
not one person
asked
a sincere question.
So
all these people worldwide that were tarrying,
or
what, they're
going to
be destroyed, you
yes.
know?
It says, Sirach 5:7, make no tarry to turn to the Lord and put not off from day to day.
You know, those guys were out there last week. You know, if I see them again next week, I might ask them, you know? Next time I go downtown, they'll probably still be out there. You know, you're putting the Lord off from day to day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That means you're tempted to know.
Yeah.
It says, for suddenly shall the wrath of the Lord come forth.
Yeah, for suddenly, when you're least expecting it, you know, the truth, the words that those men from the highways and byways, some of our apostles and elders, great millstone, the men on down, that warning of death and destruction has drifted from your memory. It's not fresh in your mind anymore. But suddenly, when that wrath comes, the wrath of the Lord, you're going to be remembered. The Lord is going to remind you, oh, crap. Those were those guys. They were saying this was going to happen.
Yep.
They were saying that the mark of the beast was the RFID chip and that every person on the planet Earth was going to be forced to take it, you know, or be put to death. They were saying that, oh, World War III was going to come, that there wasn't going to be food in my grocery stores, that these McDonald's, these fast foods were going to be shut down.
Right.
You know, they're going to remember these things.
Right.
That's when that wrath of Yahweh Shema Shai is going to come forth.
You know, that's the screen you said that because, you know, I happened to come across a video and Esau, the Lord has given Esau to know certain things. They said that when you die, you got like seven minutes of activity in your brain left. They said that's your memories flashing back of your whole life, man. All right, so when you die, you know, the Lord's going to have you flash back and remember all the wickedness you ever done, man, knowing that you were being judged because of that stuff.
You're pretty much going to remember all the times you scoffed and mocked at the man of the Lord, the times you walked past, the times you heard scriptures, cry aloud, spare not.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Things of that nature. Turn back, repent. You're going to hear all that. You're going to see all that, Joe.
Yeah.
Next thing you know, wham, bam, no thank you, ma'am. You know?
Right. It says, Sirach 5:7, branching it out, it says, for suddenly shall the wrath of the Lord coming forth, and in thy security thou shalt be destroyed.
Yeah, in thy security, you know, where you find your comfort, you know, here it is, you find comfort here in America, you know, and across the four corners of the earth, you know, you find comfort in your families, these different churches that you go to, you know, different holidays that our people love celebrating, your birthdays, you know, and those events that you find stability, you're going to be destroyed. Food, yep.
I told what she had in that bag of hers.
Yeah.
Yeah, and your pleasures, you know, because our people, instead of, you know, trying to do what's pleasurable unto Yahweh Shema Shai, they want to do that which feels good unto themselves.
So finish it out, Sirach 5:7, and perish in the day of vengeance.
Yeah, and the day of vengeance is coming. The Lord is going to bring vengeance to the planet Earth, you know, upon the wicked of our people. And all those that mock the messengers of the Most High, all those that just plugged their ears, you know, they had headphones on, they turned up the music, they try to overtalk the words of the Lord, and those men, women, and children are going to be destroyed.
Right.
You know, that Lord's willing for us to edify and let the next brother come up and speak.
All right, give me Ezekiel 2:5 and Michelle. Alright, the scriptures say every idle word shall give account thereof in the day of judgment. So majority of our people
who've been mocking and stalking, you know, coming against the men of the Lord, ultimately coming against Yahweh Shema Shai, you know, and they're going to give account thereof. The Lord's going to give a judgment to them in their day, man. Come soon.
Got it? This is Ezekiel chapter 2, verse 5. And they, whether they will hear or whether they will forbear, for they are a rebellious house.
And that's speaking to the children of Israel, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. All right, and the other scattered, the scattered Israelites, man. All right, they look like you see the nations, all right, but that are Israelites. Okay, that's speaking to the children of Israel right there. Read on. It
says, for they are a rebellious house.
They are a rebellious house, man. Rebellious, going back to fight against. You know, people always trying to fight against the word, man. You know, when the scriptures clearly gives a record of our Lord and Savior, Lord Yahweh Shai. All right, a dark-skinned man with white woolly hair. Okay, but what, our people believe in lies. And the scriptures say, a lying tongue is but for a moment, but the truth shall be established. And the truth has been established, man. It's record, the Bible has been out for forever, man. You know, but our people still want to believe in lies, man. So they're a rebellious house, man, fighting against the truth. Read on.
Says, yet shall know that there have been a prophet among them.
Hey, they're gonna know soon come there was a prophet among them, man. Okay, prophet means to tell you something before it comes to pass. Okay, the apostles and elders, great millstone on down, bringing out the 100% truth, telling you that martial law, famine, race riots, okay, more evil times, pestilences, okay, it's coming to a American near you. It's also coming across other Israelites across the four corners of the earth, man. Yeah. All right, and our people are going to learn come soon. There was a prophet among them the whole time telling them the truth, man. Giving them the truth according to the Bible.
They're going to learn and burn.
That's right.
They're going to learn from being burned. You know
that's right.
And that fire, man. Fire teaches you a valuable lesson about life, you know. When fire is on you, it teaches you a valuable lesson about life. Don't
right.
play with.
That's right.
You know?
Right.
Fire teaches you, don't play, man. Mm-hmm. That's what fire teaches you. When it's on you, when fire is consuming you, when an iron touches your arm, it teaches you, watch out for the iron.
Right.
You know? You don't play with your iron. You feel great.
Right, right.
You can do it again.
Right.
You don't do that, man.
Right.
You say, damn it now. Oh, I got to be more careful.
That's right.
And our people should be thinking the same way when you hear the words that you have about you. Know, let me tell you the moves you make, man.
That's right.
You know? Somebody's always watching. That's a beautiful point that you made, because when you get burnt by fire, it affects you immediately and after, man.
Yep.
You know, that's why a lot of people die from being burnt, man.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
It's going to shock and everything.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. Now, let's bring your precept.
This is Jeremiah chapter 7, instead of verse 1. It says, the word that came in Jeremiah from Yahweh, saying, stand in the gate of Yahweh's house and proclaim there this word.
Yeah, so stand out there in Yahweh's byways, man. And Jeremiah was a prophet, okay? And he's back here in reincarnation, standing in the gates, man, telling the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans to receive with meekness the engrafted word is able to save their soul. Right. All right? Proclaim the true word, man. Proclaim the true names of Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai, who are people ignorantly called God and Jesus.
Because one thing about the angels, they rejoice when one of our people, one of the Israelites, hear this word and repent, man.
Right.
They rejoice, man. They're not up there angry when our people turn back, man. You know what I'm saying?
There's people screaming and shouting and hoping and hollering up in the heavens when one sinner repented,
right,
man, and turned back, man.
Turn back sorrowful for what they have done. I got it right quick.
Yep.
This is St. Luke chapter 15, verse 10. Likewise, I say unto you, there is joy and the presence of the angels of the Most High over one sinner that repents.
That's how deep this is, man. That's how deep it is and important for our people to turn back to Yahweh Shai, who are people inwardly called God and Jesus. Okay? Hey, the angels in heaven are rejoicing over ones of our people that are repenting, man. Okay? Because they want to have their soul saved, man.
Right.
And not be destroyed by those nuclear missiles coming to America come soon, man. So the angels are rejoicing, man. They're happy that the people are receiving with weakness and grasp the word.
Like an Israelite come through here, they hear the word. You know what I'm saying? That's how you know they stop, they listen. You know what I'm saying? That's how you know you see them another week.
Right.
They're coming out with their sword. The angels in heaven are rejoicing, yep, man. Look, the angels in heaven are looking angrily at 2/3 of our people that just continually walk past them.
Right.
We're giving our people warning that America's going to be destroyed soon. Come, but everybody got smiles on their faces. Ain't nobody trying to get their acts together, man.
Right.
But you're going to wish that you did. Because if the angels of the Lord are rejoicing when one Israelite, a sinner, repented, what do you think their face is looking like for the one that don't turn back, man?
Right.
Come on, man. And that's the angels deadly serious. They don't play no games, man. The angels ain't smiling, man. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
They ain't coming back smiling, man.
Yep.
Go ahead, bro. It says, and say, hear the word of Yahweh, all ye of Judah, that enter into the gate to worship the Lord.
Verse now, that represents all 12 tribes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
Right. It says, verse 3. It says, thus save Yahweh of hosts, the power of Israel, amend your ways.
Mm-hmm. Amend your ways, meaning to repent, man. Okay? Hey, look, and that's why this word is coming out. Christ be Yahweh Shemel Shai. And we're commanded to go to the place of concourse. You know, so our people have a chance to repent. There's no excuses, man.
Yeah.
All right? There's no cloak for your sins if you don't take heed to the word, man. All right, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. So, amending your ways, man. Repenting, turning back sorrowfully unto your power. Yahweh Blashim, Yahweh Shai, who are people inwardly called God and Jesus.
Right.
You know?
It says, amend your ways in your doings.
And your doings, man. Okay, be sorrowful for being wicked, for going off. Idol worshiping, man. You know, into Kemet gods and, you know, Allah, Buddha. You know, getting tattooed, gang banging, selling drugs, doing drugs. You know, you got to repent. You know, be sorrowful. You know, for what you did in the past. We all had to do that, man. Okay?
Because why though? Why? Because fire is coming, that's man. Definite destruction is coming. Cannibalism is coming. A famine is coming. A race riot is coming, man. Pestilence, mold, diseases, a lack of bread, a lack of food. Your worst nightmare is coming, man.
That's right.
That's why we are here to tell our people to repent through the spirit of Yahweh, Bashim Yahweh Shai, who they eagerly call God and Jesus Christ, man. Because your life is on the line, man.
That's right.
This ain't no game. The ones of our people don't take heed to the word and receive it with meekness and humbleness of spirit, you're going to die here, man.
That's
by
right.
way of the animals eating you. Something's going to get you, man.
Right.
See, Eddie Murphy is not coming to America.
Right.
Death and destruction is, man.
That's right.
Say Matthew 22:9, go ye therefore into the highways, and as many as ye shall find, bear to the marriage.
Yeah, we command it through the power spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. The true men of the Lord, man, to come out here and preach this truth, man, to the highways and byways, the chief place of concourse, where majority of the people were gathering, you know, eating, drinking, marrying, giving into marriage. Okay? So we command to go out here and bear to the marriage. This is the true marriage, man, coming back to your power, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. Not some defiled woman wearing a white dress getting married, man. Okay? This is the true marriage coming back to your power for you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans.
Wait one more time.
Yep.
This is Matthew 22:9. Go ye therefore to the highways, mm-hmm. and as many as ye shall find, bid to the marriage.
And as many as ye shall find, bid to the marriage, man. Okay? So, hey, our people are supposed to be getting this more importantly than anything on the face of the earth, man.
Right.
You know, this is a top priority for our people to be seeking Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. Through his men. So you won't be destroyed like the brother said through the spirit, man. Cannibalism is coming. Famine is coming. Martial law. Okay? Missiles are coming. Lord Yahweh Shai is coming to shoot laser beams on this place, man.
Right.
All right? And you want to receive a seat on the chariot, man. So we're trying to bid our people to the marriage through the power of the Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai.
Yeah, because only the elect of the nation of Israel is going to be adopted back to the Heavenly Father, man.
Right.
Who is only begotten Son, Lord Yahweh Shai. The rest of them saying going to have to get it in on the other side, mm-hmm. man.
Right.
Have to get it in on the other side, man.
Right.
He don't get it in on this side, you know what I'm saying? You know. Right. You know what I'm saying on that?
Yeah.
I got something. You have something to talk about?
Yeah.
Bring out what you got, and I'm going to bring this out.
This is Jeremiah chapter 18, verse 11. It says, now therefore go and speak to the men of Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem.
Hey, that's why the Lord is dealing with the men first, the Israelite man. Okay? With commander, speak to the men of the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. The Lord is seeking men. The men first, and the men goes home and they teach their wife and kids, man.
That's right.
You know? It's a proper order with this, man.
Right.
Okay? Read that again, bro.
Start from the top. This is Jeremiah chapter 18,
verse 11. Now therefore, go to speak to the men of Judah and to the inhabitants of Jerusalem, saying, thus saith Yahweh, behold, I frame evil against you and devise a device against you. Return now every one from his evil way.
Hey, the watchman has been sent to warn the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. Start with the men. And the Lord is bringing the evil, man. The Lord is bringing the bad times. The Lord is bringing judgment, man. Heavy judgment, man. The Lord is bringing those missiles. All right? Because the scriptures tell you that's the plague that the Lord is bringing. The Lord is sending over here. Okay? So the Lord is bringing all these things. And he's sending the men out, the watchmen, to warn the children of Israel. To repent before it's too late, man. There's a such thing called too late, man. And you don't want to get caught up in that destruction that's coming forth.
Right. It says, return ye now, everyone. Return ye now.
No, 100 years from now.
Now.
For our time, our salvation is near than we believe, man. Right. Now is our time to awake out of sleep, man.
But it's going to say, remember now, thy creator, in the days of thy youth, before the evil days come nigh. Then say later, man.
Right.
Then say on tomorrow. Right. Then say next weekend. And then say at midnight. It says now, man.
That's right.
Now means now. What part of now don't you understand, man? Somebody look up now. Somebody look up now, please. You know what I'm saying? Get the meat off all. Get the meat off that bone, right quick. You know what I'm saying? Somebody look up now.
Okay.
You got that scripture too, bro? Ecclesiastes. Look up now, right quick, though. Somebody.
Definition of now, it reads at the present time.
At this present time, man. When you hear this word.
So you hear this word, turn back, man. Because you ain't got like got the apostles that came in 30 years and better. You ain't got the time that they got, man,
to get this word, man. Brothers came in 10 years, 15 years ago, 20 years ago. You ain't got the time that they had, man. Guys, know what I'm saying? It's been, a year. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. 9 months, 10 months. You ain't got the time they got, man. They have, man. You got to get it now, man. Now means what again, bro?
It says now means at the present time.
At this present time. Or now, brother. You know what I'm saying? Now means what?
At the present time.
At this present time, man. You hear the men out here on the highways and byways speaking this blessed word? Get it now, man. Or you might not. It might not be no later. You know? Everybody, y'all going to be out here later on? It might not be no later on, man. It might not be no next weekend. This might be the last weekend, man.
Right.
Get it now, man.
Right.
Shit, who knows? By next week, they can shut down the damn internet, man. Shut down. Let's come out here street speaking, man.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Shit, I should have got it then. You should have got it then. Too late. Should have, could have, would have, man. Ain't gonna add up to nothing if it ain't there.
Right.
If should have, could have, would have ain't there no more, then what is it for you, man?
Right.
Nothing. Absolutely nothing. You know what I'm saying? What else, brother?
It reads
some more heavy ones.
Yep. At the present time or moment,
damn. This is the moment, man.
Right.
This is the time. You know, you get this word now, man. Look, you don't tempt the Lord. You don't play around with him, man. You know, hold that right there. Somebody give me Hebrews 10:31 right quick. Whoever get it first. So when you get it, bring it out. This is the time. This is the moment, man. You know how they say that was your moment. That was his moment.
Right.
That was our moment. This is your moment, Israel, to get this word and receive it with meekness, man. Receive the engrafted word, which is able to save your soul. This ain't a game. We ain't out here to play no games. We're here to get the word of Yahweh, but Shema Shai. And you need to receive it with meekness, just like we did, man. We knew we didn't know nothing, man. We couldn't do nothing but humble ourselves down. You know? Go ahead.
This is Hebrews 10:31.
Yeah.
It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living power.
It's a fearful thing, man, to fall into the hands of the living power. Who's the living power? Yahweh, which name means he is, okay, who our people ignorantly call God, okay, Bahashem, through the name of Yahweh Shai, which means he delivers, he saves, man, who our people ignorantly call Jesus.
Right.
It's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living power, man. The Lord can put you in death many ways, man. Okay, you can get your head chopped off by a guillotine. You can fall from a 20-foot building. Okay, you can die in many ways, be gunned down.
Hey, I had one of these little birds just come through real fast. Mm-hmm. I'm saying, hit you dead in the eye, and I'm gonna take your eyeball out, man. Yep. Anything, man.
Yep.
Judgment gonna go forth, man.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Man, look, horrible events is gonna come to the majority of our people for not taking you to his word, man.
It's funny you say it, because that actually happened, man. It was, I don't know if you've ever seen that show called 1,000 Ways to Die.
Yeah.
A woman was in a limousine and had some
a million ways to die, on it? A thousand ways?
Something like that, yeah. Brother's gonna talk about it.
Many ways. Right. You know what I'm saying? We'll say many.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And she was, you know, in the song with the limo, she was all partying and acting all crazy. And a pigeon was flying and hit her dead in her mouth.
Damn.
And it killed her.
Damn.
See? Yeah. It's unlimited ways to die, man. Do Yahweh Shai ultimately, man. All right, that's why we got to fear the Lord now rather than later. All right, because everybody's going to fear. But you don't want to be that your last moments when you fear Yahweh Shai, right. The Lord bringing death upon you, man.
Right.
That pigeon upon you.
That's right. Right. You know what I'm saying? That's the last thing you hear.
Hey, what bird, man?
I really want the real bird, man. You know, the real number one stomp.
Right.
Oh, yeah, hold him definition on deck, too.
Okay, I got it.
This is up
now.
Yep,
up now. And two other scriptures that brother thought, hey, maybe y'all hold it up different.
This is Hebrews 10:31. It is a fearful thing to fall into the hand of the living power.
Yeah, because the Lord killeth and maketh alive, man. Okay? The Lord can bring you down in judgment, wound you, heal you, put you to death, okay? Or keep you alive and take you out of a situation of death, man. You know? So that's why we want to fear the Lord. The Lord wants you to fear Him first, man. You so-called right. Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. Okay? Before you even learn how to love them or anything else, you need to fear the Lord first, man.
Right.
You know?
Yeah. You understand? That's our main ingredient.
Main ingredient. Yep. And understand He's bringing to death, man.
The scripture says the fearful thing falls to the hand, right?
Yep.
I got a quick precept for you.
Yep.
This is Deuteronomy 32:39.
Let you know right there, the Lord got a body.
Yep.
Right. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. He don't actually put hands on you.
Right,
you
know? Right.
Stay
right.
up, man.
It's Deuteronomy 32:39. See now that I am He.
That's right, and that's Yahweh. Who are people ignorantly call God? That's His true name, man. Okay? Read on.
It said, and there is no God with me.
No, there's got to be somebody with him, bro.
And there is no God with me.
There's no God with Yahweh Shai, man.
Right.
All these false idols you see up here, Santa Maria, JC, Buddha, Allah, Scientology, all these idols, man, they're not sitting with Yahweh Shai on the throne, man.
Right.
You know, counseling about how he should put people to death, man,
right.
for going off. Okay, he's a standalone with Yahweh Shai on the right hand side, man. Bringing judgment upon the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, and other nations for being wicked.
It says, Deuteronomy 32:39, see now that I am He, and there is no God with me. I kill and I make alive.
You see, that's a fact, man. The Lord kill and He make alive, man.
Right.
Okay, Satan is not allowed to do any bidding or any work without permission from Yahweh Shai. All right, because the Lord is the one who's controlling all things, man. Okay, look what in Job's situation, Satan had to get permission from the Heavenly Father to bring affliction upon Job. Alright, so the Lord ordains all things, man. Alright, and He killeth and maketh alive. That's why I'm telling our people, hey, to fear the Lord now, man.
He brings judgment upon somebody right now.
Yep.
Right. That's judgment being brought upon somebody there for being wicked, man. Somebody.
Right.
You don't hear ambulance for nothing, right?
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
You hear ambulance for people to be getting judgment, man.
Right.
Right. Ambulance and fire trucks, police cars. That's judgment, man.
You don't hear when they're going to lunch.
Right,
you know what I'm saying, bro?
Right.
Well, you do got a party, you know what I'm saying? Fire truck coming through, you know what I'm saying? But we ain't talking about that.
Right, right.
But some people might say, well, I seen a fire truck coming through, people's up there jamming stuff over. So we ain't talking about that.
Right.
You know what we talking about.
Right. Right. You want to say something, bro?
You know, just the spirit, because there's an account in the scriptures where Yahweh Shai is seeing the angels like want to hear who can give out the best judgment, man. Like, let me see what you got.
Right. Right.
That sounds good right there.
Right. Said, bro, hit me with your best shot.
Right.
Fire away.
Right. God, so I'm gonna finish that. Deuteronomy 32:39. It says, I wound and I heal.
Mm-hmm.
Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hands.
See, none can deliver out of hands if you have a bunch of now shot. That's why it's a fearful thing.
Right.
It's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living power. All right, because when that mark is set on you, all right, hey, that's a perfect shot, man. The Lord ain't missing, man.
Right.
And there's no idols that can save you from the wrath of Yahweh Shai.
Oh, would you quote it earlier, knowing therefore the terror of the Lord
we persuade our people, man.
That's right.
We come out here week in and week out because why? We know the terror of the Lord, man. We know what kept us alive all week.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? We know who could have killed us at the beginning of the week, man. So therefore, the Lord gave us another opportunity. He kept his spirit on us another weekend to come out here and do his will. We do it willfully, man.
Right.
Willingly. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? We ain't fighting against getting coming out the door and all that, man. A brother pulling up and you peeping out the window like, God, I can't think of nothing, you know what I'm saying? So I had to go out there.
Right.
They be opening the door then. Nah, man. You see a brother pull up,
let's get it.
You know what I'm saying? You know, the God above says he's a reward of those that diligently seek him, man. If you're not diligently seeking the God of the Bible, man, your reward is death and destruction,
man.
That's
right.
You know? You may have a missile with your name on it, man. You know how big a missile is, man? Do you really want to partake in that, man?
Right.
It's a scary thing.
That's right. You got to preach
it. Because talk about still have some debt now, right?
Yeah.
Then Kabbalah knows I had the other precepts, man. Remember, now you still got a definition, right?
Yeah.
This is
Jeremiah chapter 18, verse 11. It says, now therefore go to speak to the men of Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem.
See, if I can chime in, bro, the Lord always had love and kindness and mercy on the children of Israel.
Yeah.
He always warned the children of Israel before he brings death and destruction.
Mm-hmm. Right.
All right, so the Lord is telling the prophets to speak the truth to your neighbor,
he's
man.
He's just.
Yeah.
He's just. He's fair.
Mm-hmm.
Before we went into captivity, he told us if we keep continuing to doing our madness, he's going to put us in captivity, right?
Yeah.
The Lord is fair, man.
Fair, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He's perfect balance, man.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
It says, speak to the men of Judah and to the inhabitants of Jerusalem, saying, thus saith Yahweh, behold, I frame evil against you and devise a device against you. Return ye now, everyone,
you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. The Lord is commanding you to turn back. All right? He's warning you to turn back before it's too late, man.
This is pleading with our people. Because one thing about it, the Heavenly Father knows exactly what's coming, man.
Yep.
He know how bad. He wrote a story already,
man.
So he know how bad it's gonna get, man.
Right.
So he pleading with our people over and over and over and over, man, to get it, man, to turn back, man, because he know how deadly it's gonna be, man.
Mm.
He said, "Body's gonna stick up to a horse's bridle, man. Yep. Blood, man.
Yep.
So, look, man, if blood gonna stick up there, how high the body's gonna stack up, man? Yeah, blood, which is a liquid. You know what I'm saying? Gonna stack up there, high, man. How much the bodies, man? How much the bodies, brothers? It's scary, man. But these people are gonna continue to eat, drink, give in marriage, ignore the words of the Lord. And judgment gonna finally come, though. Judgment will eventually come to this place called America. Man. You can ignore it all you want to, but finally, judgment is gonna come to America, man.
Right, that's right.
It says, return ye now, everyone from his evil.
From his evil, man, from being wicked, gang banging, selling drugs, doing drugs. You know, worshiping false idols, all right? Celebrating heathen customs, Thanksgiving, Valentine's Day, all right? All types of wickedness, man.
Pork, shrimp, crab, lobster.
Yep. Pork, shrimp, crab, lobster, abominable food. You see on that sign right there?
Oh, yeah. Practicing homosexuality.
Yep.
And all that other nonsense.
Yep.
Which is rare.
Yeah.
But hey, look.
Done.
All things are possible. Yep. You have a Chanel shot, you
That's
know?
That's right.
Just had to throw that out there. You got newcomers watching the video for the first time. And they're like, damn, they didn't say that point. So we had to say all points, man, because you never know. Can't just say smoking cigarettes, gang banging. Got to throw out the other points, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But Jake doing more than just smoking cigarettes.
Right.
Jake into all kind of madness. Oh, yeah, messing with the next man's woman.
Right.
Can't forget that.
Right.
If you're doing that, stop that, man.
That's right.
You know, whatever you're doing, man, drinking blood, being a witch and a warlock, whatever you're doing, man,
right.
Turn back, man. Oh, did you say Christmas, Thanksgiving, and all that other stuff?
Yep. Christmas, Thanksgiving, Valentine's Day, birthday,
Oh, yeah. Then cross around your neck, take it off, throw it in the gutter, man. All that, man.
And that aunt, too.
Yeah.
It says, and make your ways and doings good.
Mm-hmm. Make it right, man. Live righteous. Seek righteousness. Seek righteousness. Seek meekness,
right,
man. Okay? Seek the way of the Bible, man. The scriptures tell you how to live, man. Like the brother just named it, man. You know? You know, celebrating the high holy days to the best of your ability, keeping Sabbath to the best of your ability. All right, not defiling your temple with abominable food, shrimp, crab, lobster, pork.
Look, You ain't got to celebrate your birthday then.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's my birthday. You know what I'm saying? You ain't always be celebrating your birthday. That's a custom of the heathen.
Right.
That's basically self-worship, man.
Yeah, right.
You know?
Right.
You be mad as hell when nobody don't get you nothing. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Or where are you going to front on me, y'all?
Right.
All right, then. Wait till his shit come up then. I got something for him. His next month. I got something for him. Don't worry about it, though. I'm going to stun on him that day. Come on, man. It's nonsense, man.
Oh, you got it. Go ahead, bro.
I been saying real fast. That shows the witness of my people because I remember in the world, it was my actual birthday, and everyone wanted to celebrate and throw a party, and I went down with it, man. So they threw it in away, man.
Right.
They just wanted to celebrate something, man.
Right.
Oh, we gonna have a party.
I know that's right. We gonna do something, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Do it.
And there's a relationship. That was in the world. Relationships and best friends are broken up, but not someone not calling them on their birthday.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know that's how wicked our people are, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the evil.
Yeah.
Now here's the point.
It's verse 12. It says, and they said, there is no hope.
There's no hope, man. Our people are hopeless, man. All right, and the scriptures give you hope, man. You know, but the Lord has got to give you that gift of faith and fear, man. Our people don't have it, so they don't hope. And they don't have confidence in the scriptures.
Oh, yeah, the scriptures say, let Israel hope in the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Our people saying, there ain't no hope when it comes to serving Yahweh by Shemel
Shai.
Right. Ain't no hope in what we're saying.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I just gotta check them things first.
It says, but we will walk after our own devices.
See, our people walking after their own devices, man. Okay, in their own mind, they think the law is done away with. So they can
They're living a YOLO life.
Yep.
They're living a do as thou will life, man.
Yep.
Which that's what America promotes, man.
Mm-hmm.
That do whatever you want to do, man. But the scriptures don't say that. The scriptures say to repent, man.
Right.
You know?
That's right.
Go ahead.
It says, and we will everyone.
And that scripture right there fit Jake to the T, don't it?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It describes our people, man. That fits our people to the T. They're like, nah, I ain't listening to what y'all saying, man. Serving the Lord don't profit me nothing. That's what our people say, man. They say serving the Lord don't got no fit. The Lord too strict. That's what our people say. The Lord too strict. We can't eat our fat back. We can't eat our shrimp, crab, lobster. Yeah, the Lord say you can't. Those are abominations, man.
That's right.
You know? Can't get tattoos. You know? You can't mess with the next man's woman.
Right.
The woman can't mess with the next man. She got to just deal with her husband and him alone.
Right.
Our people are like, nah, man, ain't no benefit in that, man. Ain't no fun in that. Well, receive a missile then.
That's right.
Great. Look, when you get thrown in that concentration camp, you're going to wish you would have took heed to the word, man.
Right.
Look, them gurgle shoes ain't going to play with you up in that.
Mm-hmm.
Right. You know?
Right. Great. So I just got to say the heart is deceitful above all things, man.
Right.
Our people leaning into their own understanding is going to get them destroyed, man.
Right.
Great. It says,
would you read earlier? Then they shall know that a prophet had been among them, though. And all hell break loose in America, because America's going to be destroyed by the God of the Bible.
That's right.
Now look, you're not going to be able to keep ignoring it.
Right.
The words of the Lord, you're not going to every day, every weekend, just keep walking by ignoring the words of the Lord. Sooner or later, you got to face reality, man.
That's right.
Right.
You know, it's about facing reality, man.
Right.
Coming to the conclusion that the God of the Bible word is going to stand, man.
Right.
And not lie, man.
Right.
Verse 12. This is Jeremiah 18 and 12.
What you say, Rod? Don't let you be the next one to be in a limo and that picture comes after you, bro. Because he's coming, man.
Right.
Go ahead, bro.
This is Jeremiah 18 and 12. And they said, there is no hope. And we will walk after
our proud own statement, too.
Very
man.
Proud. Yep.
Says, but we will walk after our own. Will everyone do the imaginations of his evil heart?
And that's why the majority of our people are amongst the congregation of the dead, man. All right, there's a new worship, a new idol that they're worshiping daily. Nah, man.
Basically, that's why the majority of our people are gonna die
for
making a statement like that, man.
Yeah, sure.
You know,
yeah.
Because like said, they said they're gonna do whatever they want to. They're gonna worship the idols up on the song.
Yeah.
So that's why. All people gonna die, man, but they doing that nonsense,
that's
man.
Right.
You make a statement like that against Yahweh by Shemel Shaka, you're not talking back against us, you're talking back against the God of the Bible that's sitting inside here to give you the word, man. That's a proud statement to say, look, I ain't gonna do what the Bible says, tells me, commands me to do. I'm gonna do what I wanna do, man. If I wanna celebrate my birthday, I'm gonna do it. I see some pork chops, I'm gonna do it. You got people to tell you that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna eat pork until the day that I die.
Right.
I'm gonna smoke weed until the day that I die. That's bringing out the scripture right there, man. That's scriptural, man.
Yep.
That's what our people just said in that scripture, man.
That's right.
Because and our people will follow after like these celebrities and these leaders, because there's a rapper called dude named Popson, and he made a thing called talking to the Lord and everything in the rap. One, how he ended off was, you know, he's like, you know what, you're God, I'm man, you know, I'm gonna stay in my place, I'm gonna do me. So I was like, what? I was like, you know, this man's crazy.
No, he's insane. You know, he's a fool. Yeah. The scripture I've seen.
That's right.
Yeah, okay. This is a quick one. Isaiah 55:11. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth.
And how is the word going forth out of the Lord's mouth? Through the servants of prophets. The Lord has always done things through the servants of prophets, man. You know, and they're going to speak according to this word. That's how you know the true men of the Lord are. All right, and they're telling you, through the power of spirit, Yahweh Shemal Shai, that, hey, these missiles are coming to destroy 2/3 of my people along with these heathens, man. Okay? That martial law is coming, race riots, famine, you know, more evil times, the dollar's gonna crash, all right? Famine, cannibalism, all this is coming forth, man. This is ultimately coming from Yahweh Shemiah Shai.
Right. Oh yeah, God about gonna terrorize these people soon come, man. They think it's a joke right about now.
Right.
But you wait, when that hammer come down, you know what I'm saying? It's gonna keep pounding you people to powder, man. And the scriptures say, man.
That's right.
The Lord, when the Lord judgment come down on this place called America, the people ain't gonna have a chance in hell.
That's right.
Straight up, man. You have a chance in hell, man.
Right. Gonna be a chance for mercy. Mercy doors are right now.
Right.
You know, so that hammer come down. Hey, look, man. Hey, we all done. It's Isaiah 55:11. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void.
It's not gonna return to the Lord void empty. Like the brother was saying to the spirit, man, this is the Lord's story, man. This is his movie. So, hey, it's going to play out exactly the way the Lord wants it. Okay? And the scripture says America is going to be laid on desolate, man. And it's going to be manifested in truth. Like we're seeing from the spirit, man.
Right. It says, it shall be no more prolonged.
Hey, it's not going to be prolonged anymore. Hey, though it tarry, wait for it. But it will surely come. It will not tarry. So you see the Lord speeding up time for the elect's sake, the elect of the nation of Israel, so-called Negroes, Latinos, or Native Americans. Okay, so the word of the Lord is not being prolonged. The prophecies are speeding up, man.
It says, for in your days.
In your days. In this generation, man.
It says now.
Now, that's right. That's right, bro. This present time. Okay?
It says, oh, rebellious house.
Rebellious house, meaning the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. Okay? This is the word is only for the Israelites, man. Okay? So the scripture is referring to a rebellious house, meaning fight against, man. Who's only fighting against the word? So the children of Israel. What's the word is for?
It says, I will say the word and will perform it.
That's right, that's boss talk, man. Alright, the Heavenly Father, who our people usually call God, his name is Yahweh, he's gonna say the word, which he has been through the service of the prophets. Okay, that missiles coming for? All right, that famine is coming soon, man. All right, a lack of bread and thirst for water. All this is coming soon. Cannibalism. Okay, the dollar's about to crash. All these things the Lord is declaring that he's going to bring forth, man. And it's going to happen.
It says, thus saith Yahweh.
That's the Heavenly Father, who our people literally call God. Read more on that, bro. Read on that.
It says, verse 26, again, the word of Yahweh came to me, saying, Son of man, behold, they of the house of Israel say, the vision that he seeth is for many days to come.
See, the house of Israel, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, the ones that don't mix this word with faith, right, the 2/3, they don't believe this is coming to pass anytime soon. They think it's going to happen 100, 200 years from now. All right, but when the scriptures tell you to measure the time diligently, but World War III blowing up, that's a prophecy right there, man.
Right.
That's a major prophecy that you know that in these times, now is not salvation to people. You know? Read on.
He says, the vision that he sees is for many days to come, and he prophesied of the times that are far off.
Yeah, so they think it's far off, man. All right, but we know.
This is why their grandma been talking about it. Mm-hmm. Their daddy's been talking about it.
Mm-hmm.
I've been hearing this all my life. Well, you've been hearing it all your life, but now we at the end of you hearing it now. How about that?
Right.
How about that? Though it tarry, wait for it. Though it surely come.
Right.
Some more of that, bro, because I got a preset.
It's
the last verse, verse 28. Therefore, say unto them, thus saith Yahweh, power.
See, the Lord speaking through his man. He's telling the prophets to tell the children of Israel, to warn them. Okay? Warn them using his words, man. It's not our own words. You know?
It says, therefore say unto them, thus saith Yahweh, power, there shall none of my words be prolonged.
See? The words of Yahweh Shema Shai will not return to him void. All right? They're not going to be prolonged, pushed off, far off, man. It's coming soon, man. All right? We don't know the day and time, as the scriptures say. All right? Only the Heavenly Father, but we know it's coming soon. Right. Salvation is right around the corner for the elect. Lord willing, we're part of that fold.
Now, precept what you just said.
Come on.
This is Psalms chapter 116, verse 10. I believe. Therefore have I spoken.
All right, so the ones that's coming out here preaching through the power and spirit of Yahweh Shema Shai, proclaiming the names, bringing out the 100% truth. All right, we believe, man. That's why we coming out here making our bodies a living sacrifice unto Yahweh Shema Shai. Because we believe, man, we have the gift of faith that the Lord has given us. It's not of us, man. Okay? Fine. We're going to finish that and then jump back to the bar.
This is Ezekiel 12:28. Therefore say unto them, thus saith Yahweh of power, there shall none of my words be prolonged anymore, but the word which I have spoken shall be done.
It shall be done, man. Okay? So, we, like I was saying before, through the Spirit, man.
They're going right into the Lord's Prayer. Let thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. So it's going to happen, man.
That's right.
Go ahead, bro.
That's right. No, you said it beautifully, bro. It's gonna happen, man. All right, and we believe those things. That's why we out here in season, out of season, week in and week out, man. All right, because we know the Lord is bringing that wrath, man. He's bringing heavy judgment. All right, and we don't want to get caught up in it. That's why it's a fearful thing to fall. It's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of living power, man.
Right. It says
that it.
Yeah, how will power?
See, this is the Lord's words, man.
This is Psalm chapter 115, verse 3. But our power is in the heavens. Mm-hmm. He have done whatsoever he have pleased.
That's right. So the Lord does whatever he wants, man. Okay? If he want to bring forth death and destruction, the latest land of America desolate, that's what he's going to do. And he will do, man.
Right.
Okay? And that's why you're seeing these missiles being built. They're not built to go in museums. All right? They are instruments of the Lord, man. All right? The Lord is showing his power, his glory. He used the bases of men, these low-level Edomites, all right, you know, to build missiles, man, all right, only to destroy themselves, man, all right. Who are Edomites? The water, bro. Edomites are the so-called white people, man, according to the Bible. The water, bro.
Bring out whatever you got.
Let's finish this.
Isaiah 55:11, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I send it.
Yeah, so we know that through the power of Spirit Yahweh Shema Shai, who our people annually call God and Jesus, all right, that this story is going to play out exactly the way the Bible says it will, man. 200 million ICBM missiles will lay this land desolate. Why? Because the Bible says it.
Right.
All right, and so it's going to accomplish everything the Lord has declared it to, man.
This is the book of Amos. Chapter 2, verse 4. And it reads, says, thus said Yahweh, for three transgressions of Judah, and for four, I will not turn away the punishment thereof, because they have despised the law of Yahweh and have not kept his commandments.
Mm-hmm.
And their, it says, and their lies caused them to err after the which their fathers have walked.
Yeah, so majority of our people, man, they don't want to take heed to the word, man. So the only remedy that there is to put them to death, man.
Right.
All right? They want to continue to be corrupt, liars, caught up in all types of wickedness, man. All right? Following the ways of the heathen, celebrating heathen customs, Christmas, Thanksgiving, Valentine's Day, into feminism.
Israel, love a good time, right?
Right.
And we love having fun, you know what I'm saying, but hey, in moderation, though.
Right.
I'm saying, can't just be having fun, man. And ain't no part of your life have nothing to do with being serious.
Right.
I'm saying these are deadly serious times, man. You know what I'm saying? White affairs, things of that nature, you know what I'm saying? You know, these are all white affairs.
What's the thing of that nature, man? Come on, man. Yeah. That white gonna be turned into red.
That's
somewhere.
Right. That's right.
That's the times that we're living in. You can't be in a party spirit. The scripture said, give me one scripture, bro. Give me, brother, help me out. Give me Ecclesiastes 7:2. Give me 7:2 and then jump to verse 4.
Ecclesiastes 7:2.
Right.
It is better to go to the house of mourning.
Right, and this is the house of mourning, man. We in the house of mourning right here, man. Sign and cry for all the abominations that be done in the midst of we in hell right about now,
right?
Man. Why so much party? You know what I'm saying? We in hell now, man. We're trying to get up out of this captivity, right. Lord willing, man. Turn back to our power, man. The Lord willing, receive some mercy, man. This death and destruction is coming. We ain't got no time to be playing around, man. You know? Partying every damn weekend. Your life is consist of just partying. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing serious about it, man. It ain't nothing like no sense of urgency
right.
About you living, man. Come on. Read it again, bro. Yeah.
You're in that big spirit.
Right.
Party and bullshit.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And all this other nonsense, man. Which the Lord took him out of there, man.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Because the only thing he would have kept promoting is nonsense, mm-hmm. man.
Right.
Songs about chilling, songs about going up in the next man's crib,
right.
Girl. So as soon as you come in, you come out the closet and all that,
right.
Rob him, go in his secret safe, mm-hmm. get all his money. That's nonsense, man. You know? The scripture say don't be covetous, man.
Right.
You're supposed to want your fellow Israel. You're no man,
mm-hmm.
but mainly an Israelite man. That's what right. the want is woman, man.
Right.
And nothing he got, man.
Right.
But Biggie was pushing that. I want what you got. You know what I'm saying? Give me a little. Give me
right.
a little. And all this other nonsense. Come on, man. He was pushing. He was promoting death, man.
Yeah.
Him and Tupac was promoting death, man.
Right.
And everybody else is coming into the new age of music.
Yeah.
They're pushing death, man. Yo, look, we're pushing life, man.
That's right.
We're pushing life, man.
What point say? I think
what
I'm
saying is the younger. You know what I'm saying, bro? Oh, bullshit, man. That's why his fat ass died.
Right.
You know. It said, whosoever would not seek the Lord power of Israel shall be put to death, man. Whether small or great, whether man or woman. No respect to person when it comes to the God of the Bible. If he say turn back and repent before you die, then that's what you do, man.
That's right.
You turn back and repent, man.
Right.
Go ahead, bro.
Yep, this Ecclesiastes 7:2. It is better to go to the house of mourning.
Right.
Then to the house of feast.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You see what our people want to do. They just want to feast, man. Have fun all the time. Dress up in all white, you know what I'm saying? Just part of themselves.
Right. Right.
But what did verse 4 say, bro?
Yep, jump. Let me finish 2 up.
Yeah.
It says, for that is the end of all men, and the living will lay it to heart.
That was all in 2?
That was all in
2. So that was the one I wanted then. Read it again.
Yep.
This is, I thought we were going to have to go to 4, but 2 was all I needed. Go ahead. 2 is all I needed. The water you have, but Shemiah was shot.
Right.
Read it again, bro.
This is Ecclesiastes 7:2.
Right.
It is better to go to the house of mourning
right.
than to go to the house of feasting.
And knowing that you should be in a state of mourning right about now, that's wisdom, man.
Yep.
That's wisdom. The majority of our people are unwise, man.
Yep.
The prudent man foreseeth the evil and hideth himself.
Right.
But the unwise pass away and are destroyed, something to that effect. Yeah, come on, bro. But the simple what, bro?
But the simple are taking advantage.
Right, but the simple are taking, and that's the majority of our people.
Yep.
How long, you simple ones, will you
love
simplicity and the scorn of delight in scorning, man?
Mm-hmm.
So the majority of our people are going to die sometime, bro. Mm-hmm. You're a prudent man, a.k.a. a wise man of the nation of Israel, for see if the evil ain't going to get his act together, man.
That's right.
They see it coming, man. I believe in love horror movies, but then the scripture foretells of the horror movies mm-hmm. actually coming to pass, you know what I'm saying? And you don't want to take heed to it.
Right.
But you're paying thousands of dollars every year to go to a movie from Steven Spielberg. But look, and them people in there all white, they way down there. Look, going down there, y'all see them? I know y'all see the all white going through the cut.
Yeah, I see
all white, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Look, how they end up from there to there? Because they lost, man.
Right.
They lost, man. Ooh, look, we're trying to guide them, right?
That's right.
We're trying to guide them with this word, but now they lost by walking around the city, man. Right. Lost, trying to find the all-white part. The all-white affair part, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Brothers know what I mean.
Uh-huh.
You know?
Yeah.
Look, we wearing all white right about now, right? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know?
The
scriptures call us angels, a.k.a. messengers.
Mm.
The angels coming with all white on.
Right.
But look, we come with the pure words, the high holy words. What you going to say, bro?
Now, I was going to say, the scriptures say, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Not knowing the times we're in shows that you have a lack of discernment, man.
Right.
All right. That you know, we're in time of war, man. All right. You gotta get ready for it, man. By getting in the word, man. You so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans.
Gotta be getting your mind right, man. See, this is the time to get your mind right, man.
Right.
For real, man, because if you don't get your mind right according to the Bible, you will bug out, man.
Right.
These people are gonna literally bug out, man. These people gonna bug our brothers and seeing visions and had dreams of these people bugging the hell out. And the scriptures tell us also, man, first and foremost, these people gonna bug out, man. If knowledge and wisdom shall be the stability of that time, if you got it,
that's
if
right.
you don't got it, what that mean?
Right.
So you gonna bug out, man.
Right.
Go ahead, bro.
Ecclesiastes 7:2, it
right.
is better to go to the house of mourning
right.
than to go to the house of feasting.
Right.
Well, that is the end of all men.
And that's how you end up getting killed, man.
Mm-hmm.
Living that party life, man. You know, I'm just party, party, party. I'm young, wild, and free, right? I'm young, wild, and free. You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to do whatever I want to do. That'll get you killed, man.
Right.
Straight up, man. It says the living will lay at the heart, man.
Mm-hmm.
That's the end of all men, being in that party spirit.
Yeah.
Read that last part, bro.
Yeah. Verse 2. It says, for that is the end of all men.
Right.
And the living will lay at your heart.
Right. Once you come back to the knowledge. And the living what, bro?
Will lay it to his heart.
Right, meaning to your mind.
Right.
You're going to have it in mind. You're going to keep these words up here, man, in your mind. You're going to always meditate on them, man.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't going back to damn sleep.
Right.
Knowing that death and destruction is coming, man. Why the hell would I want to go back and start partying each and every damn day knowing that death and destruction is coming? That's going to be the majority of our
life. Right.
You know. You wait all hell break loose, and the majority of our people is in that party state when it comes suddenly upon them, man.
Right.
That's the end of all.
Right.
If that insecurity, that should be destroyed.
Right.
Perish in the day of death,
man. Right.
That was it, man.
These women ain't gonna know what the hell to do when it pop off people, man. They're living a comfortable life.
Mm-hmm.
Got on the tightest thing known to mankind. Just walking around, prancing around the city. You wait till it pop off, man. It says the living will lay to heart, man. These people are dead, bro. These people are dead. So the only thing they think about is being carnal, man. The natural man can't receive the things of the spirit.
Mm-hmm.
What we're doing right about now is foolish to the majority of these people, man. You know?
Right.
You know, it's foolish to them, man. So they're like, nah, man, oh, man, come on, man. There's music and festivals down there, man. I'm trying to go down there, man.
Right.
They ain't talking about nothing up there, not talking about. What we talking about, we ain't talking about nothing to these
right.
people. You know? What the Lord is talking about, he ain't talking about what these people got to talk about, man.
Right.
So they're like, nah, yo, the Lord ain't talking about talk, man. They talking about talking down there. They talking about, like bro said, the biggest spirit, partying BS all the time.
Right.
Go ahead, bro. And that ain't the language that our people understand. You know what I'm saying, bro? Go ahead, though.
You got a definition?
No, it's something that just popped up in the spirit when brothers say something. This is from the RT News. It says, 9 injured as fireworks display terribly goes wrong in France.
See?
Party.
See?
Right.
Party,
right.
Fireworks. Yeah, hip hip hooray, hip hip hooray, and all this other nonsense. But then here comes some injuries.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And what it say in London?
It said in France.
In France. You got brothers over there.
Hey,
I'm pretty sure some brothers in France, right?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Correct me if I'm wrong.
No, you're right.
Yep. See? Wee, right?
Look, wee,
right?
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? If I'm correct saying that, ain't that French talk?
Wee,
you know?
Yep.
Yeah, bonjour.
Yep.
You know, things of that nature, you know? Brother, no saying really going to it more than I can, but nonetheless, judgment came upon these people, though.
Yeah.
And I'm taking heed to the warning, man.
Right.
Go ahead, Ron.
And it's crazy because aren't they, isn't that where the yellow vests are?
Yeah.
In France. And
right.
They over there partying. See, they're not discerning the times, man.
Right.
What the scriptures say, the bad time for regret praise is not going to stop people from doing their wickedness, man.
Yep.
Dang.
You know?
Look though, bro, but it did, though.
Right.
But it did,
right.
though.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But it did, though.
Right.
I got that precept if you want it, though, bro, right quick. Let me just read this. The brother combined, quoted a scripture. So I just want to get it for the brother.
Yes.
I got one after. Yeah,
we in evil times, man. All right, evil meaning bad times. All right, so our people need to have a discernment, which 2/3 aren't. Okay, to not be partying and BSing, man.
This is Amos chapter 9, verse 10. All the sinners of my people shall die by the sword.
No, son.
All the sinners of my people shall die by the sword.
Hey, the ones of our people, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans that want to remain amongst the congregation of the dead will die by
right.
the sword, man. All right, it's any killing instrument that the Lord decides to bring upon you, man.
Right.
Whether getting stabbed up, a shot, a missile,
right.
okay, laser beams coming from Lord Yahweh shot, there's many ways to die,
yeah.
man. Okay. The Lord
can be out here another 8 hours, I'm saying, just going into the different ways.
Right,
still,
I know, right?
It still won't scratch the surface.
Right.
It still won't scratch the surface on how bad it can get, man.
Mm-hmm.
It says, all the sinners of my people, all the sinners of my people shall die by the sword, which say the evil.
Yeah, evil meaning bad times, okay? And these are the times that we're in, man. All right, you can discern that by the things that's happening, right? Our people are just dying by the boatloads, man.
Right.
All types of diseases our people are catching for being wicked. All right, it wouldn't be good times if people weren't dying.
Right.
You know.
That's right. Which say the evil shall not overtake nor prevent us.
And that goes back to another proud statement, man. All right, the scripture say the Lord resisteth the proud. All right, so they don't think that evil times is going to consume them, man. They don't think that all these store closings happening. It's gonna affect them. They ain't gonna lose their job.
Right.
All right. Eventually, they're gonna be homeless. They don't think that's gonna affect them. They don't think eventually, ultimately, they're gonna die.
Mm-hmm.
You know. So they're caught up in their mind. It's a party, mirthing it up. But that's not the time that we're in.
Right.
You know.
I got a definition.
You
finish
that. There's a definition of prevent. It means to keep from happening or arising.
See, they don't think that the evil times that the Lord is bringing now. All right, so ultimately they're speaking against the Lord, the Heavenly Father, saying it's not going to stop them. All right, who's going to stop us? Basically, is what they're saying, man. And that's it. You're playing daredevil with your life, man. Okay, you know you're playing daredevil with your life, and you ain't going to win that.
Man, I got a precept for this. This is a 2 Ezra chapter 16, verse 20. It says, "For all these, they shall not turn from their wickedness." Nor be always mindful of the scorpion.
A lot of people going to be catching a pure hell, you know what I'm saying? They're going to still be trying to smoke a blunt.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? They're going to still be trying to mess with Tyrone baby mama.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're going to have no food in the crib, you know what I'm saying? They're still going to be trying to invite somebody, baby mama, over, man, so they can pop her, man. That's how bad it's going to get, man. Our people ain't going to turn from their wickedness, man.
Mm-hmm.
And so they actually get put to death, man.
Right.
That's when they're going to stop committing wicked acts, but they actually get put to death, man. That's our people, man. Read that part again.
This is 2 Ezra.
You can picture it too, right, bro?
Mm-hmm.
You can picture it, man.
And this is 2 Ezra chapter 16. And I started verse 19. It says, "Behold, famine and plague, tribulation and anguish are sent as scourges for amendment. But for all these things,
spiritual licks, man. Spiritual whips, man. The slave masters, what the slaves back in the day,
yep.
With that leather strap, with whatever nails he had, they end up with fucked flesh. That's what the Lord's doing spiritually, man. He's going to do spiritually.
Right.
Great. It says, verse 20, "But for all these things they shall not turn away from their wickedness, nor be always mindful of the scourge."
So all these evil things, the Lord is bringing famine, pestilences, diseases, you know, if I didn't say famine already, okay, different just deaths, man, happen across the four corners of the earth, and mainly here in America, you know, majority of our people ain't going to take heed.
It's like the Lord going to start taking legs, arms, and everything, you'll have you hooked up to a fucking
IV.
IVs and fucking oxygen machines.
Right.
Our people still going to be thinking about doing something wicked, you know, even though the Lord is taking them through all that, man, have them homeless. The majority of people, you can even take out one of their eyes or take both of their eyeballs out, they're still gonna be trying to yo, come over and roll this blunt for me. You know, I'm blind. I said, you know, I can't see how to roll this blunt. You come over and do it for me. You know what I'm saying? Wickedness, man. You know, the Lord said, for all of these things, tribulation, I'm gonna take them through prayer hell, and Jake still ain't gonna want to return, man, and repent, man. So the only remedy, you know what I'm saying, is death, you know?
That's right. And they show you that in the movie The Purge, when secured off the city, man. All right, which was on the island, I think, Long Island. Okay, and obviously it was evil times. You could feel it. You know, even watching the movie, but majority of our people was doing wickedness, robbing jewelry stores, raping women. All right, partying. Yeah, not taking heed to the times, the certain times that we're in. All right, and this guy's the majority of our people in these times, man.
Right.
If I
may say, they
show
you that in that movie Armageddon. You know, the meteor is about to hit the planet Earth. You got Jake in the up and down cars bouncing, playing music in the street, you know? They're about to meet their demise when they're partying,
right.
You know?
They think that's going to be the last time they get to their
wickedness. Right.
You know? They don't know that this is reincarnation.
Right.
Having to pay for your wickedness. This is 2 Ezra chapter 15, verse 24. "Woe to them that sin."
Yeah, woe to them that sin. Woe means death and destruction. And what is sin? All right, transgressing the laws, man. The laws that were given to the children of Israel, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man. Okay? and the scattered Israelites, man, who look like heathens, okay, but who are Israelites.
Right. It says, and keep not my commandments, save Yahweh.
Yeah, so it'll be in your best interest to keep the statutes, laws, and commandments to the best of your ability. You want to be walking on eggshells, man, especially in these times, man. All right, you don't want to be plotting to sleep with the next man's woman. All right, you don't want to be out here committing homosexual acts. All right, and indulging in bestiality. Okay, doing all types of wickedness. You don't want to be worshiping false idols, man. You don't want to be caught up in so-called church worshiping JC, man. Okay, because the Lord is bringing death and destruction. That's what woe means.
It says, verse 26, it says, for Yahweh know of all them that sin against him.
So the Lord is beholding the good and the evil, man.
Right.
All
right,
and you're going to pay for whatever your commitment was. If you committed wicked acts, then guess what? The Lord is going to bring up forth death and destruction, man. All right, because he's beholding everything, man. He has angels keeping account of everything that's going on, man.
Right.
All right?
And he ain't looking.
Ain't looking.
Yep. Yeah, behold, he's the look.
Yep.
Right. He's looking at everything, man.
That's right.
See, the Lord don't sleep, man. All right? The angels don't sleep. But that lady had like she was an angel. So I don't rest. I don't get sleep, man. Shut up, man. Yes, you do, man.
Right.
You know? But the angels don't get no sleep. The Heavenly Father and the Son, they don't get no sleep. I guess it's a reggae party behind us or whatever. You hear them? Pond the river! Pond the river! All right, the Lord got something for that pond the
right,
river.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? Baby boat, quality yeah. boat. No, it's not. The Lord gets something for all that, y'all. The Lord gets something for that
right,
party spirit,
right,
man. Agreed. You know what I'm saying? You Benjamites, y'all the worst, man.
Right.
Straight up, man. When it comes to that party, man. Y'all ain't coming down.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Y'all gonna turn it up. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
All this nonsense,
right.
bro. Jumping all on the women, you know, all on the floor,
right.
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Going all crazy, you know what I'm saying? It's going down, man.
Right.
You remember that Smeemah, right?
Yeah.
You know? That's crazy and wild, but the men of the Lord are still pushing his word, all
right?
Yeah. We having a party right about now, man, pushing his word.
Right.
I got a precept. Would you finish with that, bro? See what I'm saying? They brought the streets off and all that down there, man.
Yep.
That's why these women come through with that all white up there, man. Want to that event, man.
Right.
Want to get a chapstick and this stuff in the store first, you know what I'm saying? Then suck it back around the block.
Right.
You know they're hollering back there. Go ahead.
This is a... 2 Esther chapter 15, verse 26.
Oh, so lock it, bro. Look, they was eating, drinking, and giving in marriage. Yep. Ain't that something? Yep. Ain't that something? The brother got it. Bring that out right quick, bro.
St. Matthew 24 and 36.
Yeah.
But the day and hour knoweth no man.
See? No man knows the day and hour. All right? But,
why they playing around then?
Right.
That's my question. Mm-hmm. Through the spirit of Yahweh by Shemir Shai, which I know already. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? It's just a little question. Mm-hmm. A hypothetical question. You know?
Right.
Being rhetorical.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It's funny because we know why, man.
Right.
You know? They eating and nobody don't know the day and the hour. So why play around, man? See, this is that main time to get right, man. The Lord is going to come like a thief in the night, though.
Right.
Go ahead.
Yep. It's Matthew 24:36. But of that day and hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only.
So only the Heavenly Father, all right, who our people inwardly call God, his name is Yahweh, he's the only one who knows the day and hour that he's bringing forth the last final moments, all right, of this wicked place called America, man.
Right.
All right, and to bring down the Edomites, man, the so-called white people from rulership. All right, so that should make us even more fearful. When you don't have the answer to the question, all right, was that question... could be life or death, man. So you want to get right and you want to walk on eggshells. All right, well, Yahweh Shemel Shai, by having faith in his word, man, keeping the statutes, laws, and commandments, you know, to the best of your ability. Because what? You don't know the day and time the Lord bringing forth his wrath, man.
Right.
Verse 37, Matthew 24:37. But as the days of Noah were, mm-hmm. so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be.
All right, and isn't the Son of Man coming? Go, Yahweh Shai. He's on his way, okay? And we can tell through the power of spirit, and look, they're doing the same thing. You're hearing the music in the background, and you're watching other brothers' videos on the highways and byways. You hear music and dancing, screaming, partying, you know, women half naked walking down the streets, drunk, out of their mind. All right, the same days of Noah, man, the same, hey, nothing new under the sun. They were doing this in the times of Noah, man.
That's right.
You know, so much more what they be doing in these times, man. My Lord Yahweh Shai on his way.
Yeah. Well, Bob, break down the rest of that scripture. Please, Bob.
Okay. It says, for as the days of Noah were, so shall also the Son of Man come, the Son of Man be. So what was Noah doing when he was a prophesied? He was building the ark.
Okay, he was getting prophesied to the people, but repent, or the Lord's gonna flood this place, right, man. You know, and we're coming that same spirit. Like, when you don't repent, the Lord's gonna bring fire this time, man. But our people hear it not, man. They want to continue in their folly and the ways of this world,
right,
you know. But in the same way that the Lord came, the people are doing the same things in Noah's time, man.
38. This is Matthew chapter 24, verse 38. It says, For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking.
They were eating and drinking, man. Basically, that's what you got going on down the block, man. They got the concert. Gotta be a concert, all that music playing, you know? And what comes with music and festivities, man? Drinking, food. The same thing's going on now. Same thing's going back on in Noah's time, man.
Right.
While he was building that ark, prophesying, same thing we're doing. People are eating, drinking, mocking and scoffing, laughing. You know what I'm saying? Noah, you bugging out, man. What the hell is rain? You know what I'm saying?
It says, eating and drinking,
uh-huh,
marrying and giving to marriage.
Yeah, because according to the scriptures, sex is marriage, man. And you know, he got people actually having sex right now. All these hotels around here, man. All right? And these guys, people actually getting married, man. Okay, we are downtown. Got a courthouse right on the next block over. So you got people going down to the Justice of Peace getting married, man. Same thing's going on in Noah's time, man.
Right. Another thing with partying comes, you know, you said drinking, you meeting up with women, you know, having sex, you know. People, like I said, getting married, what they do after the marriage ceremony, you know, the honeymoon, you know. So all these things were happening in the time of Noah, too.
That's right.
You know? That's happening now.
That's right.
It says, and given into marriage, mm-hmm, until the day that Noah entered into the ark.
Until the day that Noah entered the ark. And when did Noah enter the ark? Well, right before that first drop fell, man. Basically, the Lord had broken the ark, man.
Mm-hmm.
And then when that first drop came down, what is that? That got on the minds of the people. Well, Noah did say something about some rain. So this is what rain is? And basically, they were going down trying to beat down the ark, door to the ark, man.
Okay.
That's going to be the same thing that happens to our people at this time. Okay. When hell starts coming, okay? They were trying to seek the man of the Lord, but it's going to be too late, man. The Lord's going to take us off the streets. You know what I'm saying? Preserved, protected. You know, and then Yahweh Shemiah Shah is going to have his way with 2/3 of our people, man.
That's
right. Same thing that happened in Noah's time. Same thing that happened today, man.
It says, verse 39, and knew not until the flood came and took them all away.
Yeah, knew not, man. Why? Because they weren't discerning the times that they were in, man. They didn't mix the word with faith either. You know, when Noah's out there for over 120 years, they weren't taking heed, man. They didn't truly believe that the earth was gonna flood, because they had never seen rain, you know, on the face of the earth at the time. All right, majority of my people no one on the face of the earth has never seen America, you know, get flatlined by missiles. So although the missiles are being built, it's hidden in plain sight that those missiles are going to destroy America, man.
Right.
All right, and then the people in it, man, that don't, that aren't part of the elect of the nation of Israel.
Right. It says, he took them all away, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be.
Nothing new is under the sun, man. The same way that the people got caught off guard in the times of Noah, all right, same way they're going to get caught off guard here, man. All right, majority of our people that's not taking heed. You know, so they're gonna receive death, man. Okay, death by pain, man. Coming from Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shai.
If I may say, you see, you have a lot of, I come across a lot of articles, you know what I'm saying, on my news app, that they say that, oh, the meteorites are gonna come get the earth and destroy the earth and burn the earth up. Well, that's contrary, man. Look, the ICBM missiles, what the Lord's talking, mm-hmm, about in the scriptures, it's gonna burn this place up, man.
Right.
They're gonna show you people don't know nothing, man.
That's right.
You know?
You still gotta say Matthew? Jump to if you can jump to the 24 and 42.
This is Saint Matthew chapter 24
42.
Yep. Verse 42. And it reads, "For I was in hunger."
St. Matthew 24 and 42.
That's like 25.
Right?
This is Isaiah 13:9. "Behold, the day of the Lord cometh cruel."
No, it's coming happy with kisses.
"Cruel."
Hugs and candy bars.
"Cruel."
Snicker bars and roses.
"Cruel."
Coming cruel, man. You know? And that's why, you know, we don't know the day and hour, but we know that Lord and Savior is coming cruel. So what? That's putting fear in us, man. Because we don't want to receive what the Lord has in store for those that he's coming for in a cruel way, man. You know? The Lord, our Lord and Savior, Lord Yahushua, is coming cruel, man. Not happy, you know, with kisses. All right? Contrary to popular belief. All right? These false prophets telling our people the Lord is coming, you know, to save everybody, man. He's coming happy. No!
Right.
The scriptures say otherwise, man.
It says, both with wrath and fierce anger.
Both with wrath and fierce anger, man. That's how Lord and Savior's coming. Angry. Pissed off, man. Fed up. You know, coming to handle business and get busy, man.
Why wouldn't he be?
Right.
Here's the reason why he shouldn't
be. Right. That's right. That's right.
There's the definition of cruel. It says, willingly causing pain.
See? Our Lord and Savior's coming to willingly cause pain, man. All right? He's coming to handle business and bring forth death and destruction willfully, man.
Right.
You know, on purpose, man. It's not by accident. He shoot laser beams on his place, man, purposely destroying people as he will, man.
Right. It says, or willingly causing suffering to others.
See, our Lord and Savior's coming back for vengeance, man. Payback. All right? To pay back those who was against, you know, Yahweh and Yahweh Shai, man. You know?
And the men that he said that defeated with the word.
That's right. And the men, that's right, bro.
He said he's going to avenge his prophet.
That's
right.
Right.
He's not going to avenge his own elect.
That's right.
You know, shall I not avenge my own elect?
That's right.
The Lord's coming back, you know what I'm saying, to pay things to our people, disrespecting him and Heavenly Father, you know what I'm saying, Heavenly Father first and foremost, and Lord Yahweh Shai and his elect.
That's right. Great. That's right. That's right, bro. Water that.
It's the last definition. It says, or willfully causing pain, feeling no concern about it.
And that's the true savage, man. When you bring forth death and destruction, willfully causing pain, and not giving a damn about it, right, man. All right, that's how Lord and Savior's coming, man. You know, and he's coming as a thief in the night, just to make sure he catch the ones that he wants to catch off guard while he's bringing that pain, man.
Okay.
This
is Isaiah 13:9. Behold, the day of the Lord cometh cruel, both with wrath and fierce anger, to lay the land desolate.
To lay the land desolate. What land? Land of America, man. All right? Known as Babylon the Great. All right? The Lord has a controversy with the inhabitants of the earth, man. All right? And these Edomites, all right, are pushing forth wickedness, man. Pushing forth homosexuality, Satanism, you know, feminism. You know, all these things are against the word, against the Bible, man. You know, so the Lord is coming to bring pain, man, to lay this land desolate.
Right. It reads on.
That's it.
It says, Isaiah 13:9, and ye shall destroy the sinners thereof out of it.
And he's going to destroy the sinners thereof out of it, man. All right, who's the only one that can sin? The children of Israel, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, all right? Yeah, these heathens already got their judgment set for them, all right? So the Lord is going to do away with 2/3 and all these heathens, man, who are pushing forth wickedness.
That's this is Sirach 19:5. Whosoever take a pleasure in wickedness shall be condemned.
Yeah, taking pleasure in wickedness shall be condemned, man. All right, all into homosexuality. And even if you support it, man, all right, that means you're taking pleasure in it. All right, and the Lord's going to put you to death, man. Co-signing that mess, man. All right, down for the cause, you know. Celebrating on your birthday, Thanksgiving, you know, eating abominable foods, all right, eating bacon because it's good and you take pleasure in it. All right, when the scriptures tell you that, it's abominable food, man.
Right.
All right, so the scriptures say what, bro?
Yep, this is Sirach chapter 19, verse 5. Whoso take a pleasure in wickedness shall be condemned, but he that resisteth the pleasures, crown of his life.
Yeah, so look, if you willfully commit sin, then why follow the Savior? When he comes back with cruel wrath with fierce anger, man. Why would it be unjust for him to come back to put you to death, man? All your wickedness you've been doing, man. Okay? But we need to the rest of that pulled up the shot? That was it.
It's Sirach 19:5. Whoso take a pleasure in wickedness shall be condemned, but he that resisteth pleasures crown up his life.
Yes, it's good to say, those that love me will seek my ways. And then it says, he that fear me would not disobey. You know my word, man. All right, you're gonna try your hardest to please the Lord, so you won't receive condemnation, man, or death or destruction, man, and or destruction.
Might have hold up so lots of it started 15.
This
is Romans chapter 1:32. It says, who knowing the judgment of the Most High, that they which commit such things are worthy of death.
That's right.
Not only do they, but have pleasure in them that do.
Yeah. And so, like we were saying, have pleasure in wickedness. Because now our people, they know the judgment of Yahweh Shemashai, the men out here in the highlands and byways, right? They know it, that if they keep on doing it, they're worthy of death. But they have pleasure in it, so they're not going to stop.
Right.
So the Lord's going to destroy the multitude.
That's right.
Right. Yeah, pleasure in them that do it,
right,
too, man.
Right.
Yo, that's crazy, man.
Right.
Oh yeah, you not down with smoking this? Yo, my man, you wanna hit this L, yo? Yeah, just get down. You know what I'm saying? Pleasure those that do the work in this world, man.
Yep.
I think Sharon and Emily, you know what I'm saying? Their boyfriend's gone out of town, man. You know what I'm saying? You try to talk to a pop with me? You know what I'm saying?
Falling out a month until we do it.
That's right.
Consent not to them. Somebody try to entice you. You said to do something wicked. Don't consent to them, man. Don't take heed to what they're saying.
Right.
Yep. You want that Sirach 2:15?
Yep.
Sirach 2:15. It says, they that fear the Lord will not disobey his word.
That's why fear is important, man. We promote through the power of spirit, Yahweh Shema Abishai, fear. All right, scriptures say repetition is key, man. You see fear throughout the Bible, man. And Numbers, Deuteronomy, throughout the Bible, man. Proverbs, okay? Because we know if you fear the Lord, fear is the beginning of knowledge and wisdom, the true knowledge and wisdom found in the Bible. All right, you're not going to disobey his word, man. You're going to hearken unto the Lord to the best of your ability, man. You're going to try to please the Lord to the best of your ability. But you got to fear the Lord, man. Again, repetition is key, man. The Lord kept mentioning fear throughout the Bible, man. You know?
This is Sirach 2:15. They that fear the Lord will not disobey his word, and they that love him will keep his ways.
Why is that? Because love is what? Keeping the statutes, laws, and commandments, right? To the best of your ability. So you're going to keep the ways of the Lord, man. All right? You're not going to be trying to sleep with the next man's woman. All right, and if you truly love the Lord, and you're a woman, you're not going to be a thought and a whore out here sleeping with every man. You're not going to be worshiping false idols. You're not going to be, into chemic gods. You know, Allah, Buddha. You know, you're not going to be getting tattoos. Okay, smoking weed, selling drugs. You know. Is it on that?
Yeah.
It's fine.
I got the rest
of it. Yeah, we're past that now. Take the water.
This is Proverbs 1:7. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge.
Yep. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, the true knowledge and wisdom. All right. It's not talking about a doctorate degree or a master's, man. Whatever type of degree you got, the wisdom of this world is foolishness with the Most High, man. Because these things can't save you in the times of the wrath that the Lord is bringing forth, man. So this is the true wisdom here. The Lord is telling you to fear in order for you to get to fear Him.
This 1 Corinthians 3:19, for the wisdom of this world is foolish with the Most High.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. For it's written, he thinketh the wise in their own craft.
Yeah, the foolishness of this world, man. All right, in this society, you are deemed more respectful based off of the degrees you got, man, or how much money you got in the bank account. When the scriptures tell you that's foolishness with the Most High, man, that's nonsense, man. Lord don't care about that, man. You know? And in fact, the Lord is looking for the meek, the humble, man. All right? Not the ones who are of this world, man. All right? Because all of that don't matter, man, being of this world. All right? The scriptures say the world is enmity. The friendship of the world is enmity with the Most High, man. You know?
So obey is better than sacrifice.
Right.
Many people sacrifice their time, you know what I'm saying, to get relaxing. Fucking with some accomplishments.
Diplomas and dreams,
you know,
dreams,
they sacrifice their time. You know what I'm saying? Nah.
You
gotta obey.
Right.
You're sacrificing your time for God.
That's right.
I don't want your prayer offering. Right. I want you to obey me, man. I want you to fear
me. That's right.
And, you know, where I live at, you know, it's a major university over there, man. They just had a move-in day over the weekend, man.
Yeah.
The traffic was so congested, man. I'm looking at all the people like, man, what the? Everything they're doing is in vain, man.
Right.
It's in vanity, man.
Right.
You know? Especially the ones of our people.
Especially, you know what I'm saying, knowing that this place is going to be destroyed.
Be destroyed,
we
right.
We mentioned it earlier, somebody can bring it out. The proverb, the prudent man, perceive the evil,
mm-hmm.
and hide himself.
Yep.
Bring on like two more around the table, because I'm about to finish this off.
I got one too.
If I could just chime in while the brother's getting precept, you know, you can tell how much it's, you know, the Lord ain't dealing with these colleges and universities, man. It was a story of a woman who was graduated. She owed $50,000. And student loans. 10 years later, she paid $20,000 and still owed $50,000, man, in student loans, man. All right? That's the wisdom of this world, man. That don't profit you anything, man. Okay?
So the brothers did an article on a lady that owned like $200,000
Yeah.
Yep. I remember that. Black lady. When her husband got married or whatever, she tried to live, you know, the American dream. And it ended up being an American nightmare. It still is an American nightmare. They're gonna go to their grave, you know what I'm saying, owing that money.
Yeah.
Yeah, they say I know a lot of people, in this world that have the college degrees, you know, but they're working at a job.
Yep.
They're at fast food restaurants and driving for, you know, these good fucking because they can't get a job in their field,
They
want that drink time.
They're sending these jobs off to all the heathens that come over here, you know, they're not getting the jobs and Israelites aren't the heathens, so they don't like people, you know, and a lot of them can't find jobs, you know. Right, right, you got yours, the brother called for the precept. Yeah, this is Proverbs chapter 22 verse 3. A prudent man perceiveth the evil, yeah, a wise man. All right, not the wisdom of this world. We just proved that, brother, by Second Corinthians, you know. So to be wise, to be of the word, man.
Right.
Right, you're going to proceed at evil. You're going to be able to discern that you're in, man. You're going to know that martial law is good. You know,
you watch out all the time. I'm talking about all the time. What the deal, man?
Right.
I'm pleading with something, child.
They never going to believe in this shit.
Oh, boy, I can't be right. Look,
yeah.
I'm telling you, boy.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Same shit.
Yeah.
Same shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
I got
bro.
Stones, all that shit. Yeah. Great. They always going to be in the
room. Hell yeah. Y'all put a damn too. Y'all know what damn man?
Yeah, his brother's up there. Yeah.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah.
My name's Dino. That's all right. We're going to talk to you. I'm telling you, shit, bro. Straight up. Straight up.
All right, bro. All
right. All
right. Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shalom, on, bro. Shalom.
Brother, Lord, I got a point there. What about Gallup? Now, he's in there, man, you know? How a random guy came up to him, you know, about saying, oh, I see you guys out there doing this job out there, you know? The Lord always, you know,
you know what always showing except where everybody else is trying to miss, trying to make us feel bad about what we're doing. God, I'm always seeing some random
right.
guy, you know, and he's hype as hell.
Right.
He's hype as
right.
hell, right? That man was hype as hell, right? That man stopped this car in public, man.
Right.
In traffic. And then give a damn, yo. That let you know how hard this word is coming, man.
Right. Right.
This word is a fire, man.
Right.
The word was burning in him so bad, you know what I'm saying? He just had to get out.
Right.
Like, man,
right.
That just, look, before he even took the picture, you know, he showed some respect.
Yeah.
Hey, look, is it okay if I take a picture? If I take a selfie? Look, he pulled right here. He didn't go down there.
Right.
He pulled right here, yo. You know what I'm saying? He knew about, you like, yo, I knew about that, yo. Look. You asked.
That's right.
You came in order, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You asked. Yeah, right. Do what you got to do, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Right. That man was deadly serious. So, and the Lord gonna have men like that just come up. It's gonna be scoffers and barkers talking they crap and all that. A guy, you know what I'm saying, random guy Israelite is gonna just pull up in the car, park the car in the dead middle of traffic. He could have been in the middle lane.
Yeah, I know, right?
He would have stopped, you know what I'm saying? Yep. Busting and all that, blowing money. Right. He probably would have bust somebody's head into the White House. Why? Because he messing with the men that he learning from.
Yep.
His teachers, man.
Right.
You saw it, you watch the karate movies, so them people do it, you come up top of their teacher, right? Teacher!
Sensei, right?
Right.
I got a good piece up. This is Zephaniah 3:19. Behold, at that time I will undo all that afflict thee, and I will save her that healeth and get her that was driven out. And I will give them praise and fame in every land that put to shame.
It's pretty much you're starting to see that. That's
why I had apostles. Yep.
Notice.
Right. Great
notes on, man. Brothers going down.
Yeah. True believers.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yep. Two-thirds ain't getting out of the car like that, y'all.
You know what I'm saying?
Hell. Yeah.
Right.
Right. He's like, yo. Right. Starstruck.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Just like we're, just like, are we, when we see the apostles coming to town and all that.
Right.
Starstruck.
Right. Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like we always say through the Spirit, brother. The Lord had me say it all the time. You never know what we look like to these people.
Mm-hmm.
But look, though, that scripture is being fulfilled, though.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Lord said, I'm going to give you fame in the place that you put the shame, man.
Yeah.
Something to the elect.
Right.
True believers.
Right.
That's beautiful, bro.
Oh,
you can't just throw out that name like that.
Right.
You put that name on you. You gotta be careful. So no man over, man.
That's right.
He delivers and saves.
Right.
He wants to take you to the word.
That's right.
He wants to party and drink and drinks.
Right.
Nah, yo. Summit meetings. Everybody right. Come together. The
right.
Lord ain't talking like that, man.
Right.
Not right now, anyway. What else you got, Rob?
I still got we end off on the food, man. If that's okay with you.
This is Proverbs chapter 22, verse 3. A prudent man perceives the evil.
Prudent meaning wise, man. All right, he perceives evil. Why? Because he's going to be in his word, man. All right, measure the time diligently. The scriptures is full of prophecies. Prophecy means to tell you something before it comes to pass.
Right.
So he's looking at the news and he's linking it up with the Bible. All right, because he's wise enough, the Lord gave him that spirit to be wise enough to discern the times that we in.
Right.
All right, so that's how
you... It's like your brother knew that I got a car. He was just as happy as this brother right here.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
You tell what men and the Lord really enjoy hearing his word, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, they get excited, man.
Right.
You can see it, you know, and it gets you excited, man.
Right.
You know?
That's
boys
right.
Come up excited, man. They ain't all
right. Right.
Both excited, man. That's why it's a must that we be out here, bro.
Right, that's right.
Another reason why, man.
That's right.
He didn't give a damn. Man.
I know, right?
Hey, look, best be that who's his faith too.
He said, I told him they'd be out of the sea.
Yeah.
I told him, man. They ain't believe me. Look, I can't take a picture, they ain't gonna believe it.
Right.
They ain't gonna believe it, man.
Right.
So seeing is believing.
Right.
He's like, yo, like the stones and all that. I'm down with the stones too, yo. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
People down, man. Yep. It's a small render, but they're out here, man.
That's right.
They're out here, man.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? That's why the shepherds got to be out here. The sheep trying to get fed,
yep.
Man.
And lately, you're starting to see more solid bones and all that than before, man.
Yep. So to see a random guy like a couple of weeks ago before I left this guy, I'm like, yo, you already know what time it is. I'm like, nah, you already know what time it is.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Remember they were saying? They were like, you're like F. Esau.
Right.
You already know what time it is. Like, yeah, we already know what time it is.
Right.
You ready, bro?
Right. Proverbs 22:3.
That's a lot of images of the book. It makes it all worthwhile, right?
Yep, that's
just
right.
Just to see a brother come through. Hello, we just read that. The angels rejoiced. When one Israelite repented, turned from his wickedness.
Yep.
And he tried.
Yeah. Yep.
Not doing certain things to the best of his
yeah.
When the Lord sees fit, I'm saying, hey, look, this is will. Give him bring him out of whatever you think to.
Uh-huh.
Right. Bring him all the way.
Yep. Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. He's going to say, Lord is not unrighteous to forget the labor of love, and you're starting to see the fruits of labor, man. You know, be brought forth when people start to take heed to this word, man.
Right.
And that's all the Lord's doing. You know, we'll take credit for it.
I know.
Yeah.
Damn, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They ain't got to show this stuff.
You better
make
it. No.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That's right. This is Proverbs chapter 22, verse 3.
a prudent man foreseeth evil and hideth himself. But the simple
pass. It's a lot of hiding himself. Where in the word, man? Where else you gonna hide yourself, man? Nothing else can give you the comfort, give you the prophecies, give you the knowledge and wisdom, how to discern and carry yourself, conduct yourself in the times that's coming forth. And in these times, you know?
Right.
You know, in all times, man, but a wise man is gonna have the discernment to do that, man. To hide himself in the scriptures, man. Constantly. Meditating day and night, you know?
Look, prudent man gonna go hide himself in a bunker.
Right.
Because you know that bunker gonna be destroyed. They got a bunker busted.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. That's right.
It says, but the simple have and are punished.
Hey, they pass on and they are punished. The simple, why? Because they're not in this word, man. All right, they're doing everything contrary to the scriptures and that partying and murdering spirit.
They're
going back, flip, twerks, you know how Benjamin does, man. You know, I know how Benjamin does. You know?
Right.
You know?
There's a whole lot of nonsense going on. You got the White Affair going up there.
Yep.
You got Pond River down there. You got that down there. You got that in the park. Right. Everywhere, man.
Yep.
We're surrounded by nonsense, right?
Right.
Confusion.
Right. Yeah. Straight confusion, man. Day party, evening party, night parties.
Right. Yeah.
So they're going to pass away. The simple, man. All right, they're going to pass away and be destroyed, man. Be put to death, man, from Yahweh by Shemel Shai. And not taking heed to the word, man, and hiding themselves in the scriptures. So with that being said, I'm going to step down and let the next one speak. Shut on.
That's why the Lord said, don't
get honest, man.
See that
Jake
head there?
Yeah, all
the
brace bumps,
the back
of
his head.
Oh, yeah, so that was happening
the other week.
Damn. But can brother get a group 4 at 28? Because, that you know, just, you know, that was the spirit of the Lord that had that brother come up, stopped in the middle of the road, man. Are you seeing that our people, you know, are starting to seek the Lord more, man? You know, let's just say seeking the Lord 10 times more, man. You know,
it's Baruch chapter 4, verse 28. For as it was your mind to go astray from the Most High,
God, because the nation of Israel as a whole, okay, we went away and from Yahweh by Shema Shai, not keeping the law, statutes, and commandments. All right, you know, we did contrary to what the God of the Bible, Yahweh by Shema Shai, who the calls God and Jesus Christ told us to do, man. All right, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man. All right, you did contrary to what the Lord's will was, man. All right, which is to keep the law, statutes, and commandments. All right?
Yep. This is Baruch 4:28. For as it was your mind to go astray from the Most High, so being returned,
now you know that you're a Hebrew Israelite, man. And just like the brothers say, yo, I know what we about up here, man.
Right.
He was proud, you know, that he was an Israelite, man. You know, he was proud to know that. You know, he was an Israelite, man. All right, people coming back to it, man.
Bro, he wasn't ashamed, right? He didn't give a damn. That's a brother that didn't give a damn. Right, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
He had got it in mid-track.
Right.
And his car running there, they didn't give a damn.
Right.
Yeah, he had to go.
Yeah.
He didn't give a damn. A bus came or nothing.
Right.
He didn't give a damn.
Right. And, you know, the main thing that stuck out was, like, he said, yo, me and my boy watching y'all on YouTube and everything. That's our people seeking the Lord.
All y'all videos, yo.
You know, I was like, dang, okay. You know, he's like, yeah, let me take a picture because my boys ain't gonna believe me, man. So he's been telling people, like, you know, his spirit got fired up because he's seeking the Lord more. And he's telling other people to seek the Lord more, man. Watch the videos. Oh, what? Wow, I saw the men out there that we watch on YouTube, bro.
Right,
you know,
right.
Yo, I'm sure he ain't gonna believe me.
Right.
He had to get that proof, man. Yeah. You know. And everything, but our people are seeking the Lord 10 times more, being returned back to being Hebrew Israelites, Yasha Allah, man. All right, he princes of the power, man.
That's right. Yep. Luke 4:28, it says, so being returned, seek him 10 times more.
Seek him 10 times more. You know, whatever you was into the world with, you went all out for it, man. All right, Buzz can attest, you know, Jake, when they put their mind in something, they go all out for it, man.
That's
all right. But now we're coming back to knowing who we are, knowing who our powers are, Yahweh, all right, the name of the Heavenly Father, He is, He exists, all right, Bahashim, in the name of Yahweh Shai,
all right,
He is the deliverer, all right, who the word and He calls Jesus Christ, all right, Bahashim, Rekar Kadash, all right, in the Holy Spirit, all right, we're coming in the names of Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, man, all right, coming back to them 10 times more, going hard for the truth, man.
Right.
All right, and our people, you know, the elect of the nation of Israel is going to be doing that, man. The believers, man, those who truly have faith in the Lord, man.
Right. All right.
still say the ox wasn't on it, the ass was not sick.
You know, because you have 2/3 of the nation of Israel who don't consider, man. That was a rare thing that brother just saw up, you know, up here, man. You know, that's not an everyday thing that we see, man. All right, Jay don't just come up like, yo, I know what y'all are into. I know, hey, brother, that's me. That's all that. Like, come on, you know, the apostles and elders been out for years, man. All right, and then down with, you know, the men under. Yeah, you know, we've been out for years, and men don't come up like that, man. Right. So you tell he believed, man. You know, he's like, yo, I can't believe I actually see these men.
Right.
Yeah. And that's going to be happening more and more as we get close to the end.
Like Starstruck a little bit, right?
Yeah, you can tell because, you know, he fucked the girl, like what you said, he fucked the girl. He didn't know what part of the city he was going to be in.
Yeah.
He's having to roll a bus. He had to slam on me the whole what?
Right.
You know? Damn, you know, that damn. I've been watching him. That's damn, you know?
Exactly.
Right.
Celebrities.
Yeah, go ahead, brother. Yeah, about Shemel Trafford, he's gonna give it to me
a fame. Right.
We gotta see Esau's fame.
Right.
We gotta sell out.
Right.
Get fame.
1 Corinthians 4:9. Well, I think that Yahweh Bashimi Hawashai has sent forth us the apostles last as they were appointed to death.
Because you know, he got all these other wicked ass pastors that came before, you know, the Israelites, man. All right, but our people were into all the BS, man. All right, but now he sent the apostles, the true man, last man, to show you what is the right way to go, man. All right, starting, you know, with Elder Albert Bivens, you know, King Marshall, down to the apostles, elders, a great millstone, you know, and the men on down, you have the men of the Lord that the Lord sent out last. Oh yeah, Slaki, High Priest Ariyah, High Priest Shar, you know, you know. All these, you know, forefronter men that the Lord has set up, man. All right, they set them up last, all right, to show what is the real truth. You've been into all the madness, now it's time to show you what the truth is, man. You know, and the Lord is having his men out here in the highways and byways. That's what's important for us to be out here, because if we were out here, he wouldn't be able to stop and you know, be astonished, man. You know, to boost his faith that the Lord is really working, man.
Yeah.
You know?
It's a saying that says in the world, you know, you've had the rest, now here's the best.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
How about you all shots that he's been up there?
Right.
It's the best.
Why settle for less when you can have the best?
That's right. Said the best for last.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
First Corinthians 4:9, for I think that the Most High has sent forth us, the apostles, last, as it was appointed to death, for we are made a spectacle unto the world.
God, we are made a spectacle, man. A spectacle means to look, to be astonished upon, man. But people look at you as a spectacle, they look at you at all, man. You know, they look at you like, wow, man, you got everybody looking at the men of the Lord, you know, and like, yo, what are they doing, man? Like, that was a spectacle unto that man. He was like, yo, I can't believe I actually see them, man. I watched them, like he said, yo, I watch y'all on YouTube, man. You know, but it's a whole other thing when you see the man and the Lord in person, man. And brothers can attest to that, man.
Yeah.
You know, on YouTube, like, okay, cool. And then that man, you beat that man in person, like, yo, dang, this is even better than the screen, man.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
The definition of spectacle reads something exhibited.
One thing about these fake famous people that Esau set up, you see them in produce by
right.
Ain't the same. You know what I'm saying? When you see the men of the Lord, you know what I'm saying? You're like, man, this is more than what I was actually seeing on screen.
Yeah.
You see these fake entertainment, like, man, these people are slick.
Right.
Oh, damn, fake ass.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Or well, anybody else, you know what I'm saying? Like, man, when you see the men of the Lord, you're like, yo, you be all nervous.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Saw how he came up. Like you said, he came up respectfully. He's like, came up, you know, kind of cautious, man,
because
he didn't know what type of reaction that he was gonna get. You know, brother's looking like, oh, snap. He's like, yo, can I get a picture?
Brother's already looking dead serious.
Yeah. You know, he had that respect, you know, and you see there's a type of fear in him to even approach the men of the Lord, man. Which, you know, that's all of Yahweh by Shemuel Shai.
Yeah.
And just quick one thing, you know, another thing is that the men of the Lord are gonna be humble, but when the Lord gives the men, Lord of men fame, they're not gonna be like these rappers or these niggas out here who flaunt it, man. We heard them say, oh, we watching on YouTube, like, hey, you know, all right, brother,
You know, brothers is like, oh yeah, you know, we that dudes. No, yeah, man, because it's all up to how about you outside.
Right.
You know?
We don't deserve it.
Yeah, right.
The people don't say the so-called family, they think they deserve it. They'll say they think they deserve to be worshipped. Yeah. If we humble servants, our price is listed as 50 bags.
Right.
That's how we carry ourselves. Very humble, man.
Right.
Very meek, man. Like you said, bro, they be like, oh, we see my video on the death of God, you know, it's like, hey, now we can go all there, like, yo, okay, man. Keep it simple, man.
Fame that Esau gives you could be taken away.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But the fame the Lord gives you, you're going to go and meet some of those men, it's going to do it forever, baby.
Right.
That's
right.
Right.
That's right.
Right.
The story about the Lord made something silver and faithful, but then what now with our holy glory? You know, that's the same thing with the presence of the Lord. That's right. That means respect for something exhibited to you as unusual. It was unusual for us to be out here to these people, man. All right, it's not an everyday thing to them in their mind. Because we're they're looking up
the whole system.
Yeah, all right. No. Hey, man, look. The men of the Lord are hiring you. How about Shemashah has his word going up the four corners of the earth as a spectacle, man? This is unusual to the public, man. All right, seeing so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans holding Bibles in their hand and lifting up a standard to the Lord, man.
Right.
That's unusual to these people. They're used to our people being niggards, man.
Right.
Spicks, man. Wetbacks. Tomahawks, man. Okay, they're not used to our people being standing up and being holy, man. All right,
it reads spectacle, something exhibited to view as unusual, notable, or entertaining.
Or entertaining, you know, because some people look at us for entertainment, all right, but you know, some of us, some people look at us for notoriety or being to notice, man. Right, you know, they know of us, man. You know, you got people like, oh, yeah, I know you, y'all, the Hebrew Israelites, man. You know, and that's the Lord, Yahweh Bashimel Shai, the way it goes, God and Jesus Christ, giving the men of the Lord more fame in this land, man. All right, which ultimately, when he gives the men of the Lord more fame, the men of the Lord, all they're going to do is give all praises to Yahweh Bashimel Shai. You know, we're going to exalt the Lord. We're not going to exalt ourselves. We're going to exalt the Lord who put us in this position.
That's
man.
Right.
It's like when you do a video or whatever, brother, like your great video, brother, great video, an inspiring lesson. All praise
Kyle Lyle, Yahweh Bashimel
Shai.
You know what I'm saying?
We'll be like, where are you? Enjoy the bro. Nah, Kyle Lyle, you have busting out a shot, you know?
I'm glad that you were edified, man.
Yeah.
The spirit of the Lord, man. Because it's all the spirit of Yahweh Bashim Al Shai that allows us to do these things, man. It's not of ourselves, man. We don't take no credit. All the credit goes to Yahweh Bashim Al Shai.
That's right.
Okay, so it's good to say, at the end of the day, we're nothing but unprofitable service.
Yeah.
Because all we're doing is what Yahweh Bashim Al Shai commanded us.
Right. That's right. That's right. But by listening, being obedient, look, you got men coming up believing now, man. You know, brothers coming up, they see the men of the Lord, they hear the words, and now they believe, man, turning back, you know, making an amendment with their ways and their doings, man, or their conduct, how they conduct themselves, you know, what they do, you know, when no one's watching, all right? Their character is changed by seeing the men of the Lord out here, man, you know, hearing the words of Yahweh Bashim Al Shai.
Last definition of spectacle, it reads an eye-catching or dramatic public display.
Public display, because like I said, we weren't able to do this back in the 50s or 40s, man. We would be hung up on trees, man. All right, but now, Yahweh Bashim Al Shai, it's the time to speak. All right, it's the time to condemn America and wherever these Edomites dwell at, man. It's the time to declare destruction on Esau and its infrastructure, man. All right, so we're doing that, and we're a spectacle unto everyone on the earth, man. You know, all right.
So going back, 1 Corinthians 4:9.
Let me say, it's not every day you see somebody holding a sign saying America's gonna be
destroyed. Right, that's right.
In America.
Yeah. America.
That's right.
1 Corinthians 4:9. For I think that Yahweh, by Shimei Hoshai, has set forth the apostles last. It says 1 Corinthians 4:9, for I think that the Most High has set forth us, the apostles last, as it were appointed to death, for we are made a spectacle unto the world, and to angels and to men.
And to angels and unto men. Alright? So we're spectacles. The angels are watching, because the spectacle means to look, man. The angels are watching us. And you got men watching us, man. Like I say, had that brother come up, say, hey, brother, I watch y'all on YouTube, man. All right. So the word is going out, man, and, yeah. and men are watching, man. That's why I skipped to say, you know, in that Romans that we read earlier, you know, them now knowing the judgment of Yahweh by Shema Shai, they know it because they watched, they or they walk past. By walking past, you've seen. Everybody's either heard, seen this word, and the men of the Lord out here preaching this word, man. So there's no excuses in that day when all destruction comes, man. You know?
That's it. It's Isaiah 30 and 20. And though the Lord give you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction.
Now they're over here coming over the cargo slavers, slavery, you know, not being able to pick up the Bible, you know, though the Lord gave us all that, all right, come on.
And the water of affliction, that should not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore.
God, the teachers are not going to be removed into a corner anymore. You're not going to be able to shut the prophets up like you were able to do before, man. All right? Because it's all the will of the Heavenly Father, man. That was a charge held against you, man. Okay? Preparing the men, Lord, to death. But now the Lord's going to put up a standard. All right? You know, yeah, we know that according to the scriptures, some men are going to be beheaded for the witness of the Lord, Yahweh Shai. But, you know, the Lord is going to set up a standard so you're not going to be able to touch the men of the Lord, man.
Right.
You know? All right? You know, it's going to be known that a prophet had been among you and that you should have never touched or said anything against the Lord's apple of his eye, man.
Right. It's Isaiah 30 and 20. And though the Lord give you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction,
right.
yet shall not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore, but thy eyes shall see thy teachers.
All right. And eyes shall see your teachers, starting off with our apostles and elders, a great millstone, man. You know, on YouTube, putting up videos, you know, out there on the highways and byways, all the way down to men like us, man. All right, out on the highways and byways, he saw that man that came out, that brother, he saw us and he saw us with his eyes. We were respectful right. unto them. He saw his teachers on the YouTube, man.
Right.
That's why he was so hyped, man.
Right, right.
You know, just harping on that because that's spiritual, man.
Yeah, right.
A lot more of that is going to be happening, man.
Yeah.
You know, all right, because the words of Yahweh Shema Shai is going throughout the four corners of the earth, man.
Right.
And the elect are believing, man. You know,
what he say, me and my boys, you know, watching y'all, man.
Right,
verse
right.
21, and thy eye and thy ears shall hear a word behind thee, saying, this is the way, walk in it.
Fine, that's going to be the Lord putting that angel behind you, you know, which all brothers can attest. It was just something that in us when we heard the words that told us, hey, we got to go out there and learn
right.
and then, you know, do the spirit. Oh, we got to go out there and teach, man. And that was that angel talking in the air. Hey, this is the way.
Right.
You got to walk in it.
Same thing happened to me.
Same thing I'm saying, bro. They have same thing I'm saying.
I wish I could have got an autograph, and you ain't seen it.
Right.
Damn, I should have got a picture of
it.
That's what he did, man.
Right. He had to solidify it, man. He's like, look, man, I met the men that we was watching on YouTube, man. The one that you been watching all the videos,
right.
bro. I got to see him, man.
Right.
They said, y'all stop the traffic, man.
Right. Right.
Hey, he's going to tell a story, man.
Right.
He's going to give a testimony
that's
of,
right.
of what he saw,
that's
man.
That's right. Give his account, man.
That's right. Right. That's right.
What I would say was, my first time on this tour, I was like, yeah, you know. It's like a fire, you know what I'm saying? But you know, the spirit, you know, like you know, back in my ear, you know, like, you got to teach now. There's more to it.
Yeah.
You can't just sit there and just okay, you know what you're like.
Yeah.
You gotta go teach now.
And every brother up here can attest to that, man. Something told you, look, I gotta go out, I gotta learn.
There's more to it.
Oh dang, I can't just sit here and learn no more. I gotta go teach now. You know, and that was that angel behind the ear telling you this is the way, man. All right. And that happens for every Israelite that comes up here, but only the elect is gonna listen to the angel telling them to walk in this way, man.
Right. Isaiah 30 and 21, and thy ears shall hear a word behind thee, saying, this is the way, walk ye in it, when you turn to the right hand and when you turn to the left.
Kind of, so that's the angel telling you, like, look, this is the truth. Every Israelite, the angel sitting there like, this is the truth, but you got two-thirds of the nation of Israel listening to that demon, like, nah, go mess with Tyrone's baby mama instead, man. Don't listen to this word. Guess what? The elected nation of Israel, they're going to hear the angel.
hey, walk in this way. It's going to give you life, you know? And that's what's going to happen to the elected nation of Israel, 144,000 and the one-third, men, that's women, right, and children, man. Are they going to believe and hear the word, like, this is the way I need to get right with the Lord, man, you know?
Well, my testimony was similar, man. You know, I saw Brother Ward out there, I stopped the car, you know what I'm saying? He told me, go pull around the corner, I'll be back. You know what I'm saying? And I had on swim trunks, man. You know, I got up, you know what I'm saying? I stood there for a minute, man. I was happy to see this brother, man.
All right. And that's how all of the elect are going to be when they hear this word, man. You know? Lord's will, we be a part of that number, man. Right. You know? Hey, you know, that brother come up, hey, you never know. He might be out here next week. You just never know, man. You know? That's why we got to be out here. Because, one, Yahweh Shinah shall command us, but the nation of Israel is going to come and see the men of the Lord, man. You know? And believe.
Scripture say, how my sheep hear my voice.
That's right.
Another person's voice,
they're
not
going to
follow.
Right.
You know?
That's right.
Like you're saying, the elect,
they're
going
to
hear this word,
they're
going to be sealed.
That's right.
Proverbs
3:13. Happy is the man that findeth wisdom.
Happy
is the man that findeth wisdom. And brothers that come up, stand on the other side, and that brother that came up, stopped in the middle of the street, you saw the smile on their faces, yeah, man, when they came up and heard the words of the Lord, man, which is true wisdom, man. All
right?
He came up.
He had that camera right, man.
Yeah, he's like, look, I gotta get this right, brothers.
Right,
you
know? Right, you got the right angle on everything. Right. You're like, look at yourself, yo.
Hey, he was happy, man.
Right.
Happy is the man that find the wisdom, man.
Who was happy for him?
That's right.
He had put himself in a picture too.
Yeah. Hey,
right. Yeah. Photoshop, bro. Yeah. No, I'm
there.
Right. Proverbs 3:13. Happy is the man that findeth wisdom. The definition of happy reads, feeling or showing pleasure or contentment. God, he had delight in seeing the men of the Lord, man. He had delight because he already watching the YouTube. So he was delighted in the word, like, oh, dang, they're really going hard out there.
Yeah.
And then the Lord had him, his spirit stopping him. See, the men of the Lord out here, you know, first because the Lord put the spirit on us to come out here, right, you know, and then he stopped. The Lord was with him because man's going to the Lord. He's going up, he didn't know he's going to see his brothers out here. But that's why he stopped in the middle of the street. He had to get that moment.
That's right.
He had to let it be known that I saw the men
that was teaching him. This magic moment. Did we mention that earlier? It's that moment, right?
Right.
You know, it's time right now, right?
Right.
We look at the definition for that word now, when it's a moment.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Present time. This is the time.
Now, could you say something? That's an example for you Israelites out there riding the fence. He didn't tarry, man.
Right.
He got out the car immediately, man.
Right.
You know, that moment when when the angel told him, yo, get out the car, he didn't hesitate, man.
Right.
He got out the car and had to come see what the Lord through the men of the Lord,
right,
man. You know, I had to come see you. Hey, brothers, look, I know y'all teaching, but I gotta get a picture.
Yeah.
You know,
kind of interrupt, man.
Yeah, kind of.
He came in at the right time, too.
That's right.
When the scripture, you know what I'm saying, we just get, I think a scripture that just came out,
yep,
and the breakdown was pretty much over.
Yep.
He came out then, y'all. Yep. It was like a free space.
That's right.
The Lord
right
gave like a free space, right, where everything was kind of like free for him,
right,
to come in and do what he had to do. Right. And he was out, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
He did what he had to do, and he.
And just off the spirit that he was coming, and brothers like, yeah, man, you know, yeah. Ain't no problem, yeah, you know.
He has, you know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Brothers, I have to say, no picture.
Yeah.
No. Definition of happy, it reads, feeling or showing pleasure or contentment.
Okay, hey, he was happy, he was content with seeing the Lord out here, man, teaching the word, man. He was happy, man. He was excited, man. You know, he delighted in seeing this, man.
Oh, yeah, saying content.
Mm-hmm.
So that's all he needed.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That made his day. Like,
yep,
bro, there to say, that made his day.
That's right.
Ain't look, we ain't need to be out here rapping or nothing like
right
that. That ain't what made him get out that damn car
right
in the middle of traffic,
right,
leaning dope and not coming or rapping.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? We just out here just teaching. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
He was moved by that alone.
That's right.
But you know, we got to come in with gimmicks and all that, man.
Right.
Just come with the word, bro.
That's right.
It wasn't just his day, you know, he can be talking about it for the next couple
weeks.
Yeah.
You know? That's why he took that picture.
Right, yep. He saved it, you know what I'm saying, bro?
Yeah.
He gonna send it to his people.
Right.
He got his the original.
Right. The
next definition says carefree. Like, he didn't care. You know,
yeah,
he stopped in the middle of the road, got out on the side, you know, and
He stepped out. He didn't care what nobody thought, man. He's happy.
He wasn't embarrassed to come up to the men of the Lord, man. You know, he didn't turn a blind eye, being ashamed, you know, of being, you know, up with the men of the Lord. Because, see, somebody could have saw him, but like, yo, man, he was looking at crazy things out there, man, taking pictures. Right. What's going on, bro? Right. He didn't care, man. He stopped at Little Roy's, like, I'm taking this picture. I'm going to show my own stuff, you know? Right. He was proud to be, you know, I'm with the servants of the Lord, man.
He even said it, man. He was like, yo, they ain't going to believe me, yo. They ain't going to believe me, yo. He's like, bro, I need a picture because they ain't going to believe me, man. Right, bro. We all witnesses to that, man.
That's right.
Angels are witnesses to that, no man.
All right. We're all in that. And that made the day right there, man. Because Jacob here is not listening, man. All right. Like I said, for that happen, that's a rare occasion, man.
Yeah.
You know, Jake actually come up, y'all keep on doing what y'all doing.
Yeah.
Yo, can y'all come to my area? Other guys up there. Oh, word. Yeah, he was really excited, man. Right. You know, they hear the words, and that makes us happy, man. That we're doing the will of Yahweh outside, man. You know, for a random man to come up and be happy to hear the word,
right.
I got the definition of find in the Cambridge Dictionary. It says someone who finds information begins to understand something. It says to see where a thing or person is.
He ended up finding the men of the Lord. He ended up finding seeing where we were at, man. Like I said, who knows? He's like, oh, come down. You never know. The spirit might hop on him. The Lord might have the spirit hop on him. Just come out here. Right. Wherever the Lord has it not to be or whatever. But he was happy just to hear the words and see the brothers, man.
Right.
And that just in that, hey, the Lord delights in that, man.
Yeah.
You know?
Or by searching, discovering.
Well, unexpectedly, man's going to the Lord. How can a man know his own way?
He was riding through the city, right?
Exactly, man. So it was unexpected that he found the men of the Lord.
Yeah, and it's all three kind of things with Jake to get in right about now, man. You got Ponder River down in Sherman. You named it all earlier, man.
Right.
You got Ponder River right there. You got White Affair down there. Right. You got them down there. You know what I'm saying? See, the Lord going to send his true service to his real prophets, man.
That's right.
If you got men on the streets teaching, who's teaching the 100% truth? That's who you really want.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Well, look, a man is teaching karate. You got Bruce Lee, then you got somebody that ain't really teaching
anything.
Right. Oh, Bruce Lee, man. It's kind of tough. It's going to be hard. But when I get it down pat, it's a wrap. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
No one's going to be able to touch me, right?
That's right.
That's what you want, right?
That's right.
Same thing. Give
same thing with the men of the Lord. You want those who are teaching the 100% truth of the Lord, man. You know? Preaching everything that the Lord commanded us.
Right.
Preaching the name, which is one of the most important things that you need, that the name of the Heavenly Father is only begotten Son, Yahweh Shimei Al Shai, man.
Right.
All right, without that, that's the number one error our people make, man, calling upon another God.
Right.
All right? But guess what? If he's watching the videos, he's getting the name. You know, Jake might not know how to say it right then, right there, but, you know, trying to learn, you know, hey, I couldn't touch that. They know how to say it right then, right there. But you practice, man.
Yep.
You know?
You know, you got to just keep rewinding.
That's right.
Keep rewinding the video.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 3, verse 13. Happy is the man that findeth wisdom and the man that getteth understanding.
Getteth understanding. If you keep on watching the videos, he'll get more understanding, man. All right, which is going to build up his faith, man.
Yeah.
And the elect of the nation of Israel, that you know, they're watching YouTube videos. They're finding the camps, man. They're coming out, they're listening. All right, and that wisdom and knowledge and understanding is being instilled in them, man. All right. You know, and when all hell breaks loose, guess what? The wisdom and knowledge of Yahweh Shema Shai is going to be displayed at a time because they believe, man.
That's right,
you know, their obedience to the Lord was driven by their faith, man. He obeyed the angel in his ear because he believed, man.
That's right.
You know, he saw it like, oh, snap. But if it was some regular thing that walked by every day, he's not going to obey the angel and tell him, like, look, this is the truth. Eh, I don't believe so.
Right.
You figure.
Maybe next week.
Right. Yeah.
So you be kind of nervous though, man, to get out of the car, come up to random guys and all that, man. You know what I'm saying? You kind of nervous, yo. That man like, the hell with that, yo. I'm getting out, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And the Lord had him speak.
Yeah.
The angel made him speak what he had to say, you know what I mean?
That's right.
Because usually brothers like, yo, no pictures, no pictures.
That bro like, yo, can I take a picture? Yo, I got to get a picture. You know what I'm saying? I got to get a picture.
Okay? Yeah, if there was no pictures, he would have just came up, you know, started giving us up to himself.
Right.
You know?
Yeah. Probably would have offended. Who knows, man?
Yeah.
You know?
Those guys, man, those guys be watching these things. They want the pictures taken care of. Yeah, but you probably would
yeah. Well, you know, and even do, because people do come and ask for the pictures. What the brother would say? On the other side.
Yeah.
So it's the spirit of the Lord like, hey, brother, yeah. Go ahead, man. You know, it was a build up his faith, man. Because obedience is driven by faith. So he listened to that angel tell him, like, yo, this is the man of the Lord. He's like, look, I believe, so I got to go take a picture, man.
Yeah.
You know? So our people are believing, man.
Did he stop down there?
Nah.
Did he stop down there?
Nah. Nah. You know? He kept on riding that way. He kept on going that way, man. So he believed on the right word, though.
Exactly.
Right. Exactly. Okay. You got some more.
The Lord said, no, saying, look, man, his men will be instant in season, out of season. You know?
Right.
We haven't took no break, man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Brother been out for years, brothers. Haven't took no break, man. I think I missed one weekend, and that was because a tornado came through the city.
Yeah.
I got to be wise, right?
All
right. Yeah. This brother had so much faith, the Lord put so much faith on him, he came out looking for it. In the midst of the tournament, he was like, bro, like, I came out last week. I said, what?
They had trash cans
right out of here. Their brother holding on the trees and shit. They coming.
I just want to make sure, man. Right. You know what I'm saying? Hey, it shows the faith, the level of faith, though, man.
Right.
You know, and for him, like I said, that it was just, you know, an astonishment. Like I said, spectacle goes back to astonishment. For someone just to, I've never seen that before, I ain't gonna lie. Someone to stop in the middle of the street.
I've seen it a couple times.
To come talk to the man of the Lord and not give a damn if the traffic
will
come or not, man.
It's rare now. I've seen it a couple times, but it's rare.
Yeah.
Right. That's right. He could have sneaked this to picture, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, he could sneak one.
Right.
Have his face, you know what I'm saying? Like, hanging out the window like this before you drive by.
Yeah,
because you see people do that. They'll be sitting there in traffic and they'll hold a camera up against themselves and look like out the window and try to take a picture, man.
Psalms 34:3.
Yeah, 34.
It says, oh, magnify the Lord with me.
27:3.
Psalms 37:3. Trust in the Lord and do good.
All right, trust in Yahweh Bashmel Shah and do good, man. What's doing the good? Doing the will of the Heavenly Father, which is in these scriptures, man.
Right.
You know, following the law, statutes, commandments to the best of your ability. You know, pleasing the Lord, knowing what the Lord likes and delights in, man. All right, you doing that and doing his good pleasure, man. All right, going on.
Yeah. Psalms 37:3. Trust in the Lord and do good. So shall thou dwell in the land. And verily thou shalt be fed.
Kind of the Lord is going to take care of you if you're doing everything that he told you to do.
Right.
If the Lord told you to, what the Lord is telling the nation of Israel, you know, stop serving other gods, you know, follow after me, and you do that, the Lord ain't just going to leave you hanging, man. All right? You see that you put effort into it. Okay, cool. I got you. You know? You listen to me. I'm going to provide for you, man. All right? So that's the same thing with the elected nation of Israel. No trusting in the Lord. They believe. They have faith, all right, in the Lord, and they're going to do good because they believe, man. They believe that the Lord is going to do good unto them if they do good unto the Lord, man. You know?
Yeah. Psalms 37:4. Delight thyself also in the Lord.
Nah. Hey, no, hate the Lord, brother.
Delight thyself.
Hey, you know, don't like the Lord's word.
Delight thyself.
Delight thyself, man, which means to be happy about, man. You know, be happy, delight yourself, man. Be happy in the ways of Yahweh Bashmel Shai. And you saw that with brothers who come up here and listen and take notes. And we saw in that man, that brother that came up, man. All right, he was happy to hear the words of Yahweh Bashmel Shai to see the brothers, man. All right, because he's been watching videos. That stirred up his spirit. And then just seeing the men of the Lord, that boosted up his faith even more, man. You know, you just saw it in his face, man. So this is what the Lord is telling, like, look, delight yourself in Yahweh Bashmel Shai, man. This ain't supposed to be something.
You're
Shaw, you're with them. Right. You ain't supposed to be mad to do or upset to do the will of the Heavenly Father, man. All right?
If I may say, that's why the Spirit, that's why now the Lord has a lot of different things on the line. You know, the word is out there, you know, and why when I get mad, brothers were going live back then. Now we're going live for sincere brothers. They're like, okay, but now this one. You're live, they're somewhere downtown. Yeah. And y'all will look. That's what you say.
That's right.
You say seek and you shall find.
That's right. That's right.
I'm going to finish it out. This is Psalms 37 and 4. Delight thyself also in the Lord,
right,
and he shall give thee the desires of thy heart.
And that brother that had the desire to see, you know, had the desire to come up to the men of the Lord, watching the video, he's like, ah, I wish I could see them brothers, man. Right. You know, that was a desire that he had, man. The Lord fulfilled. Why? Because he delighted in what he heard, man. He delighted in hearing the words of Yahweh Shema Shai, seeing the men out there in the highways. Yeah, man. Yeah, hey, for the kingdom, for me to repent. You know, who knows? You know, he's watching videos.
See a brother with necklaces and all that, Joe.
Yeah, you know, bees, right? Dope, yo. Hey, bees, yo, moan that, Joe. Moan that, Joe. That's why, yo, I'm moan that, Joe. I got them, yo. I got them, yo.
He's excited, man. He's delighted in what he saw, man. Guess what? Two-thirds of the nation of Israel, they don't delight in seeing the men of the Lord out here preaching the word, man. All right? You know, that's a rare thing, and only the elect of the nation of Israel would delight in the Lord's word and seeing the men out here preach the word, man.
Right.
Be happy when they see it, man.
Yeah.
All right? You know?
You read that part one time and then we get to
verse 4, right?
Yeah, verse 4. Psalms 37 and 4. Delight thyself also in the Lord,
mm-hmm,
and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart.
Right. And the desire of the humble, which is the elected nation of Israel, ultimately, is the kingdom of heaven, all right, to be a ruler's world in righteousness under the Lord Yahweh Shai. Yahweh by Shemal Shai, man. All right, and guess what? The elect, they're going to receive that, man, because they delighted themselves in Yahweh by Shemal Shai, man. All
right,
the Lord's going to give them that desire that they've been, that they're yearning for, man. Lord's going to be a part of the elect. Brothers want the kingdom, man. That's the desire of the humble, man. Lord's will be a part of the elect, man.
Right.
And you saw that brother, like I said, just highlighting that,
yeah,
his desire, one of the desires had to be to come up here and meet the men of the Lord, and the Lord brought that desire to pass.
He did that.
Yeah. Right. That's right.
Go to the next desire now.
That's right.
You get yourself together, you know what I'm saying? Start teaching.
That's right, bro.
Up on a level.
That's right.
Grand more.
That's right.
Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 1. Remember now.
What is the other one, too? The other one about Proverbs 3. 8,000.
Rubies. Oh, yeah.
Hi.
Yeah, because that's the spirit that the verse is bringing out. Because the scripture talking about the kingdom of heaven shall be likened unto a treasure that is hidden in the field. You know, that man coming to find it behind the treasure. He sell all that he has when you buy the field, you know?
Yeah.
So what, you gotta forsake everything that you got in this world.
Yeah.
He just stumbled upon the most valuable thing on the planet, this knowledge.
All right.
It's not like it's not something you find every day.
Right. Hey, it was the elect, you know, the nation of Israel, I found it, but the rest were blinded, man.
That's,
you know?
Right.
They're gonna receive and find what they've been searching for, man. All right, you know. But guess what? 2,000 nation of Israel, they were blinded, man. They're not gonna find it, man. And then be destroyed.
Spiritually, public clearinghouse.
Rich bitch.
Proverbs chapter 3, verse 13. Happy is a man that findeth wisdom, and a man that getteth understanding.
Right.
Verse 14.
Hold on, brother.
You don't see people make that type of sight when they go into the church, though.
All right.
You know what I'm saying? They smoking cigarettes, putting out cigarettes. You know what I'm saying? They putting cologne on.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
They
look at the car.
Right.
That man was hyped when he saw the true man of the Lord, man.
And it wasn't fake, brother.
Yeah.
It wasn't fabricated, man. It was all authentic.
They didn't know how to act, really.
Yeah.
That's how you know it was real.
Yeah.
Right. You know what I'm saying? They just came out with whatever that was in them
right
at that point in time.
Yeah.
You know, tell them on faith.
That's right.
Proverbs 3 and 14. For the merchandise.
They just came straight with it. You know what I'm saying? Okay. He ain't sure. He wasn't ashamed. Right. He excited. Or none of that. He didn't act like he was too cool to be excited.
Right.
The man was just excited, yo.
Right.
It was straight raw.
That's right.
Yeah.
Honest. It was honest. He was completely honest. He's like, look, man, you know.
You know, when Jake get honest and excited about things, sometimes they stutter a little bit. You get that little, you don't know really what to say. It's like everything's kind of like pouring out of you, but you can feel the bottle of the person. Like, okay, this person is really sincere. Yeah. You know?
Genuine.
That's right.
Proverbs 3:14, for the merchandise of it is better than the merchandise of silver.
Kind of wisdom, all right, which we know wisdom is the fear of the Lord, okay? Because wisdom, that is the fear of the Lord, and depart from evil is understanding, okay? To get that, to have those things, is better than having precious rubies and gold, man, all right? Because those precious rubies and gold is not going to save you out of death and destruction, man. The fear of the Lord, that is your treasure, man, all right? And strength for your salvation, man. All right, you fearing Yahweh by Shemal Shai, which is that wisdom, man. All right, that's the best thing to have on this planet Earth, man, is the fear of the Lord, which is wisdom, man, all right?
It reads on, and the gain thereof, then find gold.
Yeah, then the gain thereof, then find gold. So it's better to gain wisdom, all right, which, you know, is the fear of the Lord, you know, the knowledge of the Heavenly Father and what He delights in is better than any precious metals on this earth, man. Any money, any riches, that is compared to nothing to the wisdom and knowledge and understanding of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai.
That's right. Proverbs 3:15. She is more precious than rubies.
Mm-hmm. See, because wisdom, that Sophia, you know, compared to a woman, okay?
And all the things thou canst desire are not to be compared unto her.
Kind. Everything that you desire cannot be compared to her, man. Because through wisdom, all right, knowing how to please the Heavenly Father, the Lord is going to give you everything else, man. So all you need is wisdom and the fear of the Lord, man. All right, and everything else will be given to you, man.
That's right. Seek ye the kingdom of heaven, and all things shall be added.
That's right.
Seek ye first the kingdom of heaven,
right,
and all things shall be added.
That's right. Right.
That's it, bro.
Yep, that's it on that. Go back to Ecclesiastes.
Yeah, that's that off.
The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 12, verse 1. Remember now thy creator in the days of thy youth.
Yeah, remember now the creator, Yahweh Shemal Shai, who born and calls God and Jesus Christ, all right, in the days of your youth, when you're young, when you're able to do things for the Lord, man, when you're able to stand for 3-4 hours, man, when you're able to go out in the winter, in the hot summer, all right, in the spring and the fall, man, all right, when you have an able body for the Lord, man, okay, you know, seek the Lord, man. All right, go, go, go.
While the evil days come not.
When the evil days come not, man. All right, before it's too late. Because soon we're about to come into a time, real, real soon, all right, where the evil days are to come and our people will be looking to get right with the Lord, but it's going to be too late, man. You know, they didn't seek the Lord when before death and destruction come, because our people are always on that damn CP time, man. All right, well, you know, always late to the party, man. Guess what? You can't be late to this party, man. You gotta come on time, man. You know, because when the party starts, the doors are shut, man.
That's,
you know,
right.
Nobody coming in, man. You know,
nor the years draw nigh. Mm-hmm. When thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in them.
Fine, you know, the Lord's not dealing, like brothers did earlier, man. But you old heads, man. All right, you know, you failed. You know, people say you failed this generation, man. Okay. All right, you didn't tell this generation to follow the Lord, man. So what the Lord had to do, they had to raise up young men, able bodies that fear Him, man. All right, that are honest and do and tell the truth, man. All right, and that love Yahweh Shemal Shai, ultimately fear Him first, man. Okay, as brother read earlier in that scripture, that they saw men who feared the Lord, man. All right, who told the truth. Okay, the Lord is raising up young men, man. Able bodies who fear the Lord and will preach His word, no matter if it be the death of them.
That's right.
You know?
That's it on that, bro. Right? So,
I was like, so with that, hope brothers is edified. You know, it's a beautiful weekend coming to preach downfall and destruction and annihilation at this kingdom called America, aka Sodom and Gomorrah, aka Babylon the Great, aka Egypt, man. All right? Before we go, first and foremost, I'd like to give all praises, honor, and glory to the Heavenly Father and His only begotten Son.
Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim, Rakak Kodash.
Double honors to our apostles and elders, the great millstone who grew well and taught us this truth. All right, the 100% truth according to the Bible. And shalom to all the brothers out there, the four corners of the earth,
pushing this word in all righteousness, sincerity, let Shalom.
Shalom.